But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
I guess we signed, huh?
Did we?
Oh, man.
A lot of speculation.
Everybody was speculating.
You guys are signed?
Jimmy.
I'm not. But it's not, there's no aggressiveness. I'm just working out one more final thing, which is very close.
Oh, you're not allowed to be here then.
No, yeah, it's not the 4th, right?
You gotta leave.
Is it the 4th?
No, today.
Oh.
You're technically not allowed to be here.
Oh, well.
Please leave.
I'm a guest. I'm a guest comic today.
We want you to come in at 8.
I know. But Travis was walking by. I said, let me just come in. And Roland said, go again. Hey, guys.
Jesus.
So what do we got? 2 more years?
2 years of shenanigans, hijinks, and...
2 more years, we'll make it 20 years together.
Oh, my God.
That's 10 like years on satellite radio. I think that'll be perfect. I think that'll be perfect. That's a perfect place to leave it.
10 years.
It'll be 10 years on satellite and 20 years for the Opie and Anthony show.
Amazing.
Just couldn't leave with that weird 18 years, 8 years.
What about the people that... used to say on message boards and stuff, done. Remember that one?
Yeah, they were...
Remember that, like, years ago after we first got to New York?
Years ago.
These guys ain't going to be around for another week.
Years ago, a month ago. Oh, when October comes, you're fucked. It wasn't fucked. We were going to get what we wanted or we were going to leave.
How many times?
I guess we have to say SiriusXM, thank you. For real.
Hey.
We didn't get everything we think the show needs. I'll say it that way, but they came forward a bit.
I think
they came forward a bit. I want to try to start on the right foot.
Oh,
with this
on a positive.
I'm gonna try.
Well, here's what I think happened. I think they know that a certain company wants to come in and swoop in here and sweep out some people, and they thought a good way to get them back was to give us a good deal.
Do you know why you think that's what happened?
Oh, absolutely. They want to fuck them bad, you know, and we are the dick.
This show is the upper decker in the toilet.
Exactly. That's how I totally see it.
You think we have perfect timing for once?
Perfect.
Oh, fuck these people.
They can leave and go, we're gone, but you got to deal with these assholes and what we signed them to.
Do you really believe that?
Yes.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I absolutely believe
that. I had an inkling, because stupid Bob,
stupid Bob.
He is just stupid. he works hard for us, but he's just dumb. He's like, I go, what's going on, man? Because we, without getting into details, we all had our things we wanted, and we all were getting our things. And I'm like, what's this about, Bob? He goes, I think they're finally realizing that the show is really good. And I think they're starting to appreciate what you bring to the company. I'm like, shut up. That's not what it is.
We are a high and hearty fuck you to the people, the incoming.
I really think they finally have realized what you guys are all about.
Really?
After all these years? I'm like, no, Bob, something else is going on. It's obvious. What is it?
Thanks.
And can we exploit that?
Yeah.
Exploit them. So,
Jiminy Cricket.
Yeah, two more years.
Yeah,
2 more years, and for whatever reason, thank you to SiriusXM because we needed some things, and we got some things.
Yeah,
some things. But I think Anthony might be right on this because I was very suspicious.
Oh yeah, that's.
I'm like, no, Bob, there's something else going on.
Oh, that's exactly what it is.
You think?
Wouldn't you want to just trash the joint before you leave? That's pretty much what it is. Here you go.
Yeah, we did all right. We did all right, man.
Yeah, not too shabbily.
Anyway, I don't know what else to say about it.
Yeah, it's like, hi, and we'll be spending our mornings with you people like we have. Welcome aboard, anybody new. We're Opie and Anthony. We will be here.
It wasn't a guarantee. How many times did you tell Bob, I'm done? I said, I'm done, like 4 or 5 times.
Did you 4 or 5 times?
And Bob goes, really? I'm like, yeah, call him right now and say, I'm done. Like, okay.
Yeah, there were a couple of sticky points.
Yeah.
A couple of sticky points, but, yeah, Bob went in there.
I work hard for my money. So hard for it, honey. Oh, guys.
I think they really just have realized.
Shut up. Guys. No. They didn't realize that we're a good show, finally.
Oh, God. They finally realized. Guys, it's... Oh, Jesus. I can't believe it.
Bob really is a dumbbell.
Yeah.
I said something casually about doing this thing, you know, because again, they're being fine with me too, but it's like the way it wound up in the contract was not what I had said. It was like, no, Bob, it's not what I said. It was a casual thing. I meant to extend that, not the.
Right.
And it's like, now I just got to go back in and fix it. It's a minor thing, but it's like.
It just takes so long for them to fix things.
It really is a fuck. Well, it's all the weekend you can't get.
Just jot it down and fucking send it to me.
Bob was panicking on Friday.
Oh, God. Ah, Jimmy.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Jimmy, I don't know. We're both going to be on the unemployment line.
Then
I think I sell my house. I don't know what to do.
And then my fax machine in my building was out, so I go to Jimmy's building, and Jimmy's literally behind me for 10 minutes and has no idea. Well, I didn't have an idea either until I heard the lady go, Jimmy, can I help you? And I turn around like, Jimmy, Jesus.
It was so, because I was down there getting the exact same thing faxed that he was, which was signature pages. You know, you got to fax your signature to your agent. It's just what
you're
you got to do.
You're not allowed to have a fax machine in your apartment?
I'm more than allowed. I just don't.
Exactly.
I hate fax machines.
I'm saying, why wouldn't you?
I don't. Because whenever I have one, it doesn't work.
Why? Yeah.
What? You need one, don't you?
No.
I used to have one until my kid, you know, used it to, I don't know.
Put a fucking cheese sandwich through.
No, he likes standing on it and jumping up and down a lot. I lost that a while ago. I lost that in the first year of his life.
No, I've never had a fax machine work. I've never had good luck with a fax machine.
You probably had shitty fax machines.
Maybe, but I don't fax enough now.
Yeah, I just figure, what the hell, I'll just go downstairs every once in a while.
Yeah.
But Bob's always trying to get me to print things up. I'm like, nah, I can't do that.
Yeah, and that's
sorry.
It. Like, sometimes you got to print shit up. And
yeah, I used to have a really nice printer with faxing capabilities.
Oh, that got
it was beautiful.
On.
Yeah, we thought it was a great idea to just keep it on the floor.
No. Oh, no.
Right next to the couch. So it turned out to be his step when he was a little younger to get up on the couch.
Oh, see that.
And then we watched that for, I don't know, months and figured it was okay to allow
that. That's a durable machine.
I fucking had to throw that away.
I don't know if I can fax for mine.
Bill Burr is on the hotline.
Wow.
Hey. It's really early, Bill. Are you calling me to beat me up about the Jets?
Oh, hell no.
Oh, good.
No, I just called to jump in about the fax machine stuff.
Yes. Billy.
What's up, Bill?
I am in the airport in Jacksonville, Florida, and I called in to pour myself out to let people know that my special is available for download on my website as of this morning.
Nice, BillBurr.com.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Bill,
I'm pouring myself out, but I've had a fax machine. A Panasonic since 1999 that did. Bobby Kelly told me to get it works.
he talks everyone into technology.
He is a tech guy. He does know his shit.
Yes, he does. To the point you can't even lie to him if you try to make up something cool that you have.
Right.
To see if you can get him to freak out. He's just like, they don't have that yet, dude. No, they don't, dude. Take down, kid.
He knows. Wow, yeah, and still working. And don't you need it, Bill? Bill, don't you need yourself a fax machine in this business we call show?
I got to be honest with you. When people come to my house and they see my fax machine, they always make a comment making fun of the fact that I still have a fax machine. People have moved. People always come in. Hey, Bill, how's it going? Hey, do you mind if I send a fax? They always go like out of their way. I don't know. Isn't there some new way people like scan it and just phone?
You can do that. You could scan it. And...
Can't you do digital signatures too now?
Yeah, I gather. But I mean,
we just type your name and that's supposedly okay now. That's
yeah,
a little strange.
Yeah, can't you just like upload what your signature looks like onto the internet so someone can steal it and just start putting it on there?
Yes.
Is that the only thing left that isn't up on the internet that's about yourself?
I had signed something recently where it was a digital signature. And as you type your name, they just assume that that's how you write your G.
That's you.
And my name, you know, Greg Hughes, whatever.
That's
it's really
you.
Strange. I'm just typing, watching the signature. I'm like, but that's not my signature. How is this legal?
They'll do fingerprints eventually. You could probably put your fingerprint on something.
Future Jimmy. When is this happening? Jimmy.
Well, Bill's right. If your signature's up there, it's going to get stolen and downloaded. So it's either going to be your retina scan or your fingerprint. Just something that is going to be has to be unique. Although they can see your fingerprint too once that's up. So that's there goes that
retina theory. Scan they've had for a while. I mean, Captain Kirk used it in order to find out the info for the Genesis.
Well, that's
maybe. Don't worry. The internet is totally secure.
Yeah, of course it is. We all know that.
It's all secure. What more can we voluntarily just put up there? Big Brother is ourselves. We finally have done it, where all the information, all the pictures, videos, everyone ratting each other out. It's just each other. It's turned out to be our own selves. Thank you.
Hey, Bill.
I think that deserved a little bit of applause, actually.
Well, I know.
Oprah applause.
Well, it's nothing.
Discover who it is, and it is ourselves.
It is ourselves.
Just
thank
a little
you.
Early.
Bill Burr pulling out some artillery I saw down there.
Yeah?
Some pictures of Bill Burr shooting guns.
Oh, yeah. When in Rome. I'm in Jacksonville, Florida. I ate some alligator. I shot some guns. And I did some shows at the Comedy Zone.
They love their guns down there. Jacksonville is a... hotbed of activity for guns.
They got like a whole they had like a whole section of the store that was just silencers. It was like cell phones on display.
Wow! How great is that?
They had a fully automatic machine gun with a silencer on it on the wall.
Holy mackerel!
Man, that's amazing.
Hey, how fun is shooting? I'm just a pisser.
Anthony, how many years in jail would you get if you get caught with a silencer in New York?
Holy shit. You're definitely going away.
Going down.
No ifs, ands, or buts about it. A couple of years.
Yeah, I should probably watch what I'm saying. I'm sitting in an airport talking about fully automatic.
Yeah, and they have silencers, too.
You don't quite fit the demo, but I understand. Yeah.
Hey, what happened? I mean, your Pats didn't look too good in that first half, but then gave the Bills a fucking ass kicking.
Yes, they did. I actually went to the Jaguars game, so I got the game taped. I haven't seen it yet. My buddy said after a replay, you know, questioning whether Tom Brady went in or not, and they actually said, you know, they confirmed that it was a touchdown. They said they cut to his face, and he said, "Fuck you, bitches."
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's all over the internet today. Yeah? He's on the bench, and clear as day, he said, "Fuck you, bitches." And he was basically talking to the Bills fans.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, man.
I'm going to predict some bootleg T-shirts the next home game.
Yeah, fuck you, bitches shirts.
Yeah, they're going to love that up there in Boston. Fucking Jets stink.
Yeah.
Holy fuck, they're horrendous. They're 2-2 officially, but they have no business even being 2-2. Yeah, here it is. Watch here. Fuck you, bitches.
Oh, yeah.
We just got the clip of Tom Brady.
He does say fuck you, bitches.
Man, the Jets lost 34-0.
Yeah, no. Couldn't help it. You don't have Revis, but you guys are in rough shape, and I have no sympathy for you. I really don't.
Yeah.
I don't like the Jets or their fans.
Well, that's why I'm bringing it up. Let you rub it in.
You start screaming Super Bowl. You're annoying.
No,
so.
No. This
I didn't rub it in. You brought it up. If you're going to bring it up, I'll
no. I said I brought it up. No, Bill, listen. I said I brought it up so you can rub it in.
Oh, so I can rub it in. Yeah, nah, I'm not kicking you when you're down.
I don't give a fuck. This team stinks. And then people on Twitter, fucking relax. They don't. They stink. Sanchez is a horrible quarterback.
No, he has
a good game every four games.
Opie, it's Sanchez. Remember?
Sanchez. Yeah, he was called that
for
a while.
New York is the king of giving somebody an epic nickname after two good games.
I want to hate Bill for epic. That, but he's right.
An epic nickname.
You mean like Jeremy? Oh, yeah. You mean like Linsanity?
Yeah, Linsanity.
Insanity, man, genius.
Yeah.
Godzilla. Anybody, you do anything in New York, it's just so gigantic that you get this unbelievable nickname.
And they, you know, they were getting their asses kicked, and they still didn't put Tebow in yesterday. I don't know what that's about. You would think they would want to like get him some playing time just for whatever reason, you know. But they sat him, and the beauty of Tebow, it's 34-0, and this game is over. He's still on the sideline with his helmet on, like, no, man, I'm ready
to go
in. Put
me in, coach.
He's got that attitude. I like it.
Oh, there you go. He's a go-getter.
I don't know. I think the guy's a winner, but I just don't know how he fits in the NFL. You ever see the guy throw? I mean, it's horrific.
It really is.
He's got happy feet. I mean, you're going to put him in and run the wishbone? Like, how long before the NFL coaches figure out how to stop that?
I don't know. You're absolutely right. The guy cannot throw at all.
Yeah.
But then again, can Sanchez at this point?
What's that?
I said, then again, can Sanchez at this point?
I don't know, but if you put Tim Tebow in as the coach, you should be wearing like a floor-length raccoon coat. We're going to run to the right, see? And then we're going to run to the left. Yeah.
Nah, whatever.
The razzle-dazzle play.
The forward pass? You're insane.
I got to find a second team already.
Jimmy, I had a great time. I don't know if you ever played the Comedy Zone down here. One of underrated club, man. It's awesome.
I don't think I ever... I've been to Jacksonville once. I don't know if it was for that or for something else. I think I had a six-hour layover there from when I went to Cuba with Jeff Ross. I think that's my entire Jacksonville, Florida history.
Horrible.
Did you get out of the airport?
No, I mean, we were just going
just hung out.
From the military, flew us in there, I think. But no, I would like to do that. The Comedy Zones are pretty good.
Yeah, no, it's a fun room, and, you know, I wouldn't stay there. I would definitely get the hotel down the street.
Oh, wait, do they have a condo there?
Yeah, it's at a Ramada.
Oof.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, the Comedy Zones are not always in the most prestigious buildings. I've noticed that, too. Where's the one in Harrisburg? There's a Comedy Zone, which is a great room, but it's in a very weird little motel hotel area.
Ugh.
You always stay down the street.
The club is great. The club is great, but it's inside of a Ramada that has not been remodeled since the Everly Brothers first floor.
Are you saying the accommodations are not up to snuff?
Yeah, but the room is great, and the crowds were phenomenal. So
very cool.
I would love to do that, because I kind of like working in Florida, and I do pretty well down there, except in Miami. I didn't draw for shit. I have only done it once. I don't think I'll ever go back.
I heard your name about 50 times this weekend. They were all, Opie and Anthony fan, when's Jimmy coming down, blah, 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 blah. I heard that like 50 times this weekend.
Oh, good, man. Good, good. I'll definitely get down there then. I need another market I can go in and half sell. It'd be nice. I need to listen to my Twitterers again and then realize that, wow, there's only 10 people asking me to come, and I bought it hook, line, and sinker. I'm just so eager for love. Jimmy, when are you coming? You got to book me there, Pete. There's an onslaught of requests. It's fucking, it's 10 people.
Ouch. Ouch.
Jimmy, when you come into Davenport, you jump on those tweets?
Yeah, no, I just kind of ignore them because I know they mean well. And it's like, how many times should you write never? I feel bad. And if I get enough of them, I'll go. Like Oklahoma, right. I want to go to because I've gotten thousands of emails since we've been on satellite from Oklahoma. So that's my next goal to a place I've ever been.
Let's go there.
I would love to do a gig
that's
in Oklahoma.
Show. Yeah. Let's go there, man.
Have you been? Cool.
Have I been to Oklahoma?
Yeah.
I passed through one time, went to a Thunder game there.
Oh, okay.
That was it. I never performed there, though.
How was that? How was that going to a Thunder game? How were the fans down there?
Oh, so it was like a college atmosphere.
Yeah, that's right here.
It's like a bare-bones like stadium. They don't really have any luxury boxes. It's all made out of concrete, so it gets loud as hell in there.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
You know, they're beyond excited that all of a sudden, like, they're in the league, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so, right on. right
we
on.
We should see. Dude, I got to send you some of the pictures of some of the fans at the Jaguars game. I wasn't too, you know, I wasn't too nice the way I was taking pictures. But there was, dude, it was like 90% humidity with some of the fattest people I've ever seen.
Oh, God. Like, wow. Damn.
Where are those pictures going to be?
I actually gave them to my guy who does my podcast. I think hopefully he put them up. I texted to him late at night. There was some. There was one. There was two guys. Like they were in the front row, leaning on the railing. They literally looked like rhinos from behind.
Look at Bill. Bill rules.
Dude, do you book will you book the a show that night, or will you go in a day early for a place like that to go to the game?
Oh, I actually hung around for an extra day.
Oh, you do? Okay, so you can actually go and enjoy the
game.
But
you've said in the past you book gigs depending on sporting events at times, right, Bill?
That's how I've been doing the road. That was the 110th franchise I've seen a home game of a professional one. So I'm running out of teams. I only got like 10, 15 left I got to see. So.
Have you done every baseball ballpark?
Yep.
You have?
All of those. Yep.
Wow.
Seen all of those.
Wow.
Seen every football team but about four, every hockey team but about three, and I need like seven basketball. And then I'll be alone with my thoughts, Anthony. And that's when it gets scary.
Yeah, then it gets scary when you don't have any more distractions.
Why don't you start the college circuit?
He does college sports.
I'm going to LSU, Alabama later on this year.
Oh, so you'll book like if you'll book close and do the gig, and you'll actually just travel to a city that's really close by just to go to the stadium.
Yeah, as opposed to just sitting there in the comedy condo, you know, ordering from Steak and Shake and wanting to kill myself.
Right, right.
So like, all right, well, I'll you know, Oklahoma. I saw the Miami Heat game where Chris Bosh and what's his face almost got into a fight. But I've seen some decent stuff. Some of them have been more pathetic. Going to a Golden State Warriors game by myself might have been a low point.
But you know what? That's not. I've done the same thing for escorts, but not nearly as much. I've literally probably booked four or five gigs because it was escorts I wanted to see in that city.
And your fans are in the audience thinking, "Oh, he came to see us." No,
yeah, they have no idea. You can thank Craigslist or fucking Euroskai.
They have,
no idea.
They have a really good escort in that town.
But I've never done what Bill did, which is I think that's a great thing, man. It gives you a reason to kind of go to a place you wouldn't go before.
But I got to do something when I'm there, or else I can't do the road anymore. As far as like, you know, going to the local mall or something like that. Like honestly, like the suicidal thoughts become like overwhelming. So yeah, I'll go to Jacksonville. I'll go to a gun range.
Jesus.
I'll eat some alligator. I'll go see a game. I mean, I have to do something. I'm basically. I should probably be filming this. This is probably just some. Be a great travel channel show of just some lonely loser out there.
Jesus, Bill.
And then, like, promoting everything. I'll be just talking about how fat everybody is and how the food sucks.
What time do you get up in the morning when you're... When I'm on the road, man, I go to bed at, like, 4 or 5, unless I have press the next morning, and get up at, you know, 4 in the afternoon for gigs, if I can.
No, actually, I've been staying out late. We were staying out late last night with these fucking scumbags. At the bar downstairs, and this guy was hilarious, man. This guy's like just turned 40 years old. He broke his arm falling out of a tree. He somehow, like, he's like the married father of three, and he's a complete drunk. And he had this thing anytime anybody walked up to him and told him, like, he'd just go, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, as they were talking to him. He said it to the manager when the manager told him to, you know, that he was cursing too much. And then right as he had this gift that right as he was about ready to get kicked out, he goes, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. And he just kept getting out of it. It was hilarious, dude. At the end of the night, looks like this Korean War veteran comes walking by to say goodnight, you know, old greatest generation, you know, class guy is going to say goodnight to everybody wearing this Jaguars jersey. He goes, he's like, goodnight, fellas. And he just goes, fuck you. Fuck you. And he just starts saying that to him. The old guy snapped. He's like, let me tell you something. You better make sure you know who you're saying that to, you know, because the next time, blah, 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 blah. And then he just looked at all of us and he goes, lesson over. But at that point, we actually told the guy to go to bed because it was embarrassing, man. He was cursing out an old man.
Jeez.
Burzy, yeah, my buddy I tore with, he said, no, fuck you, go to bed. And the guy looked at me. I said, yeah, beat it. Your night's over.
Beat it. Left. What an asshole.
Yeah, he was. He was an asshole. But I got to tell you, when he said fuck you to the manager six times and then said, no, I'm just kidding, and got out of it, I actually had to admire him.
No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, that works.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Where are you off to, Bill?
I go to L.A., and then I'm at Go Bananas out in Cincinnati next week. I have 7 weekends in a row. It's a long story how this happened. So,
wow. Oh, my God.
The last one is in Australia.
That's awesome.
Oh, that's cool.
But that's the end of my year, though, basically. Then the rest of the stuff I have is kind of close by. And, yeah. Mm.
How long are you doing in Australia? I've heard those are great fucking gigs.
Yeah, I'm doing, I think 3 nights out there, and I'm just doing a show at like the Sydney Comedy Zone, whatever they have.
Right, right. There.
And then I'm doing 1 night at the festival. It's not one of those just the last things, so I'd be on one of the galas or something like that. So tickets are doing all right, though, man. I was actually happy. Like we've coming close to selling a couple of them. It's like little 300-400 seater, but you know, other side of the world, different hemisphere. I'm pretty excited.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a really good market for American comics. And everybody says, you know, that they actually get this radio show there. So, like, people listen to it online, I guess.
Yeah, I don't know.
But Australia's supposed to be a good market, so it's a smart thing to do. Mm-hmm. You're only going for, like, 4 or 5 days, though.
Well, I'm going to stick around a little longer. I'm going to go snorkeling in the Great Barrier Reef.
That's
try to drown out the suicidal thoughts before the shark hits me, you know?
Jesus. Bill.
You depressed, Bill? Are you in a depression? Are you just kidding?
No. If I just do the road every other week, I'm in a good mood. But if I do it 7 weeks in a row, I really start examining what exactly I signed up for.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Stepped on the stage.
Damn it.
Well, what I was talking about the last time I was on your show is what I can't stand is, like, how much money do you have to make where you can just stop for a while? Where you can just sit still? The second you stop working, It just starts, everything just hits you. All of a sudden, you need a new roof. Something happens, right?
New roof,
car shits the bed. Taxes come in. I'm getting killed. Killed in taxes.
Yeah, I just got a hammer to the teeth with what I have to pay. Oof.
Not to bring it up politically, but enjoy January 1st when everybody's taxes even go up further.
Yeah. Punch your banker in the face today, everybody.
You guys both, you looked at that differently than you both.
You certainly did.
That's the tab we're paying. Those guys chewed and screwed on all of it. Bastards. So, Anthony, are you still holding on to that it's one of the political parties that's actually...
Uh-oh. Oh, Bill, I'd be crazy to even think that.
Here we go.
That a signature could keep the fucking taxes from going up January 1st, though, you know. That's kind of crazy for me to even think.
You just buy it hook, line, and sinker, don't you? You look at the talking head, the fall guy, the guy they signed up.
The fall guy, is that who it is? I love you,
Anthony, do you honestly think that your vote, like when they're talking on television, that they're actually talking to you? Do you really believe that?
No.
They care about Anthony?
No. I just don't want to pay such high taxes.
Damn liberal conservatives.
I'm sorry. Bill knows it all. I forgot.
Right wing tree hugger.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Hate them all, right, Bill? Hate them all.
This is how I look at it. Yeah. If I contribute $100 to a campaign, that really pales into comparison to the $50 million that any corporation can put in.
Right.
So at the end of the day, they can actually, there's people who donate so much money, they can call the White House the way you call one of your buddies.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I don't see that as being a good thing. No.
Yes.
No.
Those are the guys. Those are the guys who are calling the shots.
I just don't want to pay as much tax as I do. It's crazy. And I certainly don't want them going up.
Someone's going to have to pay for it. We're fighting two wars, the housing market collapse. Those rich guys aren't going to pay for it.
We're still fighting two wars. We're still fighting two wars. What happened?
One of them.
I think one's over.
One
and a half.
One and a third.
1.3.
But we lost our 2,000th guy.
Still over there.
Yeah. Fuck.
We still got all our stuff over there.
We still got our stuff laying all over from World War II. Still. We still got our stuff.
Yeah.
In Germany. It was already Europe.
That'd be cool to just walk around and check that shit out. Where is that shit? Just everywhere?
Yeah, our shit. All our shit.
Is it just everywhere, here and there?
But I was more talking our financial shit.
Yeah.
And our troops are still in Europe because of, what happened after World War II. It's crazy.
Oh, yeah, you couldn't let Germany go back to their little ideologies again. Oh. That was a two strikes and you're out. We're staying this time.
Yeah.
If we leave, we know we're coming back.
we kind of let Japan on their own. We'll see how you do. But Germany, they've proven they can't be left alone to their own devices.
Yeah.
Billy.
Oh, is this petering out? I just feel I'm feeling petering right now.
I'm petering.
Well, Bill, we're going to go to billburr.com. We're going to download your special, right?
And I hope so.
And
if people don't buy this thing, I'm going to shoot my next one on an iPhone.
Might as well.
Not a bad idea.
Yeah.
Hasn't been done yet.
I saw Bill at Caroline's.
Amazing,
holy
right?
Fuck, is he funny. God damn. just fucking. I got angry when my peripheral vision saw that red light that tells you, you know, get the fuck off the stage light. I was like, ah, goddamn it, I'm fucking having a good time here.
Really, we had funny. A good time, man. We hung till like 4 in the morning, I believe that.
Oh my god.
How long did you shoot the special?
I staggered home after that night.
Really?
Yes. Me and Bill just on the street corner. I don't even know where we were, somewhere on 8th Avenue, just yapping as these degenerates are walking past us. Bill finally goes after like a half an hour. I was like, maybe we ought to go before we get our head caved in.
You know what those guys said as they were walking by? Look at these degenerates on the
look at these drunks
on the street corner.
Exactly.
Who are you kidding? As you guys are pontificating, I'm sure.
Oh, we were holding court. Holding court.
We were part of the problem.
Yeah, we were holding court on 8th Avenue.
Yeah.
Great.
Well, I'm about ready to go board my plane, and I'm going to step into the aisle so we can help expedite the loading process.
Yes.
Very good, Bill.
Oh, Bill.
You're a good man.
That's the only place you ever hear that word.
Expedite.
I'm convinced it's a word they made up to try and sound official.
Bill, don't dwell on your thoughts too much. Keep distracted, and we'll see you when you come back.
You know what sucks is we can't get a direct flight back from L.A. to Jacksonville, so now I have to go fly to Dallas, get off a perfectly good plane, and roll the dice the next one's going to work, too.
Oh, God, that's I hate connecting flights. Yeah. That's the worst.
Oh, that is terrible. There's no reason you have to. You're all the way up there.
Right.
You got to come
going.
All the way back
just
down.
Going.
Just to go all the way back up again.
Oh, it's the worst.
It's annoying.
What about when they go way past your destination?
Oh,
then you have to take the plane backwards.
Yep.
Oh, like when you went from the East Coast to Vegas back to LA back to Vegas.
Yeah, the time that XM at the time fucked me and didn't have a ticket for my wife.
Mm.
So I had to wait, and then we had to fly to LA to get to Vegas.
Yep.
All the way to L.A., wait 2 hours to go backwards.
How fun is that?
Backwards.
I remember having to go from New York to Salt Lake City to Boulder, Colorado.
Oh, right.
In a death plane over the Rocky Mountains. Oh, that was some of the scariest shit ever.
That made you nervous?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Totally.
You guys remember that story with those pilots who were just up front shooting the breeze? And they were supposed to land in Chicago, and by the time they realized it, they had already gone past it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Had to turn around.
Hey, come on. You missed an exit talking to your buddies, you know.
Is that the one on the Northwest flight when they fell asleep?
Oh,
I don't know.
That might have been an L.A. flight where it was at night flight, and they dozed off, and they overshot, and they were over the ocean.
Yeah, I remember that
up.
One,
that was
too.
A Northwest
yeah.
flight, I think,
and
too.
And the voice recorder, you could tell that they had just woken up.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's bad.
That's not good.
The machine is just driving people. It's just flying people. Yeah, the machine will do it. That's frightening.
That's like one of those sci-fi movies, and then the robot wakes you up, and you're on the other side of space.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, I'm getting on the plane. I got to jump off the phone. Thanks.
All right, Bill.
BillBurr.com. Thanks, Bill.
Bye.
Have a good flight, or two flights.
Bill.
Yeah.
Bill's hilarious.
I love when the guys check in early morning.
Yeah.
After their long weekend, wherever the fuck they're doing their comedy.
We had such a blast, man. We were just fucking hammered.
Yeah.
I didn't even know what we were drinking at one point. I do remember the taste of Jägermeister at some point.
Fuck.
But Bill and like...
Joe DeRosa.
I guess DeRosa, they like drinking whiskey.
Really?
Yeah, they'll just drink like whiskey. In a warm whiskey in a glass, it's like, it just doesn't sound good.
Does Bill drink? I haven't hung out with Bill in a while, like in a social setting. I didn't think he drank at all, actually.
Oh,
God.
No, Bill will drink.
Bill will throw him back.
Okay.
Not as often as a lot of people I know.
Like Joe DeRosa?
And me and DeRosa. Yeah.
Joe's a drunk, right?
Joe is a drunk.
He's a real sot.
I love sot. When you go out with Joe, you know you're drinking. He's one of those guys that'll just, after a few, he starts pressuring you to get as drunk as he is. So he's just lining up shots of everything. Come on, come here, get up here. Like, oh boy.
Yeah.
Here it goes.
That whiskey, though, is rough.
Oh.
You ever do whiskey?
I can't.
You used to do the whiskey sour.
Whiskey sour?
In college. So I'll have a whiskey sour.
No, I like...
But straight up whiskey? Fuck
mixer.
No.
You know, I can't drink straight whiskey. There doesn't seem to be any reason for it.
The only one I could do is... I could do a martini every once in a while.
Yeah.
Not some of the... I could do it just a straight up
like
martini.
Like a vodka martini,
yeah,
something
yeah.
like that.
I like a little flavoring in the martinis, but I could do one straight up.
I like
But besides that, I can't do hard liquor, man. Not really.
No.
Not straight up.
Contrary to popular belief, aside from, you know, shots of Jaeger every so often, I'm not a hard liquor kind of guy. I'm more just beer and wine.
And a little Jack and Coke.
If I'm going to be drinking booze, it's mixed drink like a Jack and Coke, Captain and Coke, vodka OJ, vodka OJ, cranberry, vodka OJ, cranberry, pineapple.
Do you do the sea breeze?
I love a good sea breeze.
Can I have a sea breeze, please?
Yeah.
What's in a sea breeze?
It's sea breeze. Cranberry.
Yeah.
Vodka and grapefruit, right?
Is that grapefruit or pineapple? I don't know, one of those.
I believe it's grapefruit.
I'd know any of those things are pretty goddamn good.
I was a bartender for a while. I should know my drinks.
Oh, damn.
It's the only other job I had.
I definitely like a good good vodka juicy drink.
You know how lame my jobs have been over the years? Caddy.
Caddy.
Worked in a video store.
Oh.
And bartender.
The video store? Were you the counter guy?
Yeah. I told the story. It was in Geneseo.
This is late.
Well, no.
You weren't kind. You did not rewind.
I'm going to put an age on myself. But I worked at a video store when they were really important. And it was in Geneseo. And I was desperate for money. And my whole fraternity would come in and just take movies.
Oh. And the mom and pop stuff.
Yeah, but I got fired because they would just take the movies.
Oh,
I'm like, dudes, you got to bring some of these movies back.
Oh, and they wouldn't bring them back.
And then we had, I think, if memory serves me right, 2 or 3 VCRs you could rent out. And no one had VCRs yet. So, of course, we had a couple of those at the fraternity house. So no one could really rent the VCRs out.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, did I get fired.
You were definitely not.
Oh, boy, did I. And I told the story. They would come in. You got to remember, no smartphones, nothing.
Yeah.
So, like, it was slow. The fraternity guys would come in to see me because it was on Main Street up there in Geneseo. And we would watch porn in the actual store.
Oh, that's great.
And then sometimes it took, you know, I couldn't get my button on the stop fast enough when the moms were coming in with the kids and whatnot. It was a fucking mess. I don't think I lasted more than 3 months there.
Was that pre-Blockbuster?
Yeah, man, this goes way the fuck back.
Video stores just popped up, and they were mom and pop shops all over the place.
It was a good little family business.
Yeah, small little business. You'd go in there, you'd have to sign up. You'd have to usually pay a fee when you first went in, like in order to join,
like $100 or something.
And then you needed a credit card, and then I remember the horror if you lost a movie because it was over $100 to replace
one
VHS tape. Fuck yeah. They would be like, oh, well, I see we don't have, I'm trying to think of a good movie, Top Gun.
Right.
Yeah. You didn't bring back Top Gun. That's $120. What?
I hate franchises. Always have. And, you know, going back to, like, the little video stores, you remember every town had this little family business. It was nice. And then slowly but surely,
Blockbuster
just fucking
saw.
Taking over everything.
They saw what
Do you
was
remember
happening.
Growing up, we did a lot of work around our house, so we always had to go to the lumber guy.
Yeah.
The local lumber guy.
Yeah,
people
forget.
The
lumber store.
There's like two of those guys left in the whole country.
Yeah, now you just got the big
My
home
dad
depots.
Would go, like, hey, we got to get some 2x4s. So we would jump in the car and go, I forgot the name of the place, but whatever. And we'd go over there, and it was like a social thing. Hey, Ed, how's it going? Well, I need some 2x4s today. All right, pull the truck around the back, and Jack's back there. He'll help you out. All right, thanks, Ed. Need some nails, too? Yeah, I guess I'll take some nails. It was just this, like, give and take.
Yeah.
And then fucking Home Depot. We're fucking taking over all this shit, too.
There's something to be said, though, for being able to get what you're looking for.
Because
the video stores, I remember going in trying to, you know, you're going in going, I'm going to get Lethal Weapon. And you walk out with fucking, you know, Ernest Goes to Jail or some
That's why you had to join a couple different video stores.
We joined
a few in the neighborhood.
A clip.
I don't know what it was. I think it was sort of affordable.
The Blockbuster would have 75 of whatever new release.
New release. The mom and pop store. It's like, sorry, it's still
I know,
out.
But you can't. It's like this, though. I'm putting my hands up in the air. Topsy-turvy.
I know, it's
like,
kind of the.
You're right. Because then when Blockbuster did hit, you're right. You never
got everything.
You knew
you
the movie would be there.
Dude, they ruled. They had popcorn, candy. They were fucking pretty good, except for their rated X, their lack of X films. But they had.
Yeah, that was like, the heyday of renting fucking movies, man. Remember that? Blockbuster, just huge.
It became an event.
Yeah.
Hey, let's go. Let's go find a movie.
Let's go to Blockbuster.
Find a movie.
I was Mr. Late Fee. Oh, boy, could I never fucking bring the videos back on time. ever. And then you reach a point. It was almost the same feeling I got when I used to cut class, and I would cut for so long that I couldn't even go near the building anymore, near the side of the building where the class was, because you were embarrassed because you didn't want to run into the teacher.
Right.
That's how I felt about the video store. I'm like, I can't go back now. I owe so much in late fees. Right. It's embarrassing to walk up there.
Yeah.
And they would call you. Oh, you're gonna
bring the movie back?
No
one has been
able
to rent that movie in 2 weeks because you have it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It would be some fucking really current movie that everybody wanted.
But meanwhile, Netflix, it's like, you know, you have fucking 9 movies for a year. It's like, would you like some more?
Yeah,
well,
I have other.
But you're happy to send you some more.
I don't know how that business works.
They just want to get rid of their fucking DVDs.
I haven't returned a Netflix movie in 5 years, I think.
Dude.
And they've never complained or asked for them back.
I still have that new release, Gladiator.
Right. the mom and pop thing, though. Fuck.
Yeah.
I hate that went away. I hate that you go to a city or a town and it's all the same shit. I remember growing up, it was so cool when you went to another town. They had their own shit to check out. Their own hamburger joint. Their own video store. It was cool.
Yeah.
Their own movie theater that was a little different. Now it's all the same. Why would you even travel?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of that guy.
What? You like franchises?
Like, I hate fucking mom and pop outfits.
God, I love it the other way around.
Oh, God.
Really?
Yeah, some motherfucker in there trying to sell you something that you don't need because he doesn't have what you need.
So you'd rather just go to chain stores?
Well, this fashioner will work. I need a certain screw that this one is good, too. No!
I kind of like that. I miss that.
Yeah?
Yeah. Although I was in Home Depot recently, and wow. What do they got, like 200 employees?
Yeah.
What's that about?
Mm.
They want to make sure that you can find someone, huh?
Well, it's usually a pain in the ass, though, to still find people. Oh, I'm sorry, I'll call. And then they get on the little speaker. You're a service person in hardware? And then you're sitting there going, and no one's running for that one.
Home Depot is just overwhelming for a guy like me.
Now you run around.
The Opester's not good with his hands.
The Opester likes pre-assembled.
Oh, boy, does he. You should get my wife on the phone. I yell and scream putting this shit together, and it's easy shit to put together.
Yeah.
They have made it easy, but
a lot of those little fasteners that go in that little round hole, and then you turn it with a Phillips head screwdriver.
I yell and scream. Half my stuff is already damaged because I threw it against a wall. Oh, like a nice finish is now has a scrape in it.
That's got to be a treat.
It's so frustrating.
Oh, God.
So frustrating. And you don't need any tools, really. They give you everything in the box, but
yeah. The worst is when shit's missing. That, to me, I can't deal with it. Mm. When something in the box is fucking missing.
That's rare, though.
It's rare, but it seems to always happen to me. Yeah, because there's nothing you could do about it.
Right.
Fuck, I need this belt.
They finally figured out the hard plastic, though, I noticed. Although, last night I had to get a new electric toothbrush, and I was opening that shit up. I was convinced I was going to literally,
yes,
slice a finger off.
Oh, it's...
Because I was too lazy to get some kind of scissors.
That's what it is. You need
start trying to pull that shit apart, and you're risking severely cutting your hand.
Ow, it's razor sharp, and then that crimped edge thing they do.
Right.
If you pull that off, it becomes a dagger.
Right. And then if your hand slips, you're in deep shit.
Dunsky.
But for the most part, I don't see that anymore.
Yeah.
For the most part, it pulls apart nicely.
Yeah, they
kind of
figured it out. I guess the lawsuits were getting a little high.
Yeah.
Mm. Wow.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I remember that
guy
shit.
Who started Blockbuster used to own every Florida sports team.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, good for him. Used mom's car to rent Showgirls. NC-17 version, good for you. Has a hacky and neat to screw, but they sell 3-packs line.
Go for it.
Tony!
Hey!
What do you got, buddy?
This Home Depot crap, you're so right, man. You go there and you try to buy, you need 2 screws?
Yeah.
You can't buy 2. They come in a pack of 3. You want to buy 4 screws, you always need 4 screws. You can't buy 4.
Thank you. Food's here.
Ah.
All right.
Yeah.
We got lots to do today. We got to talk about the fucking Fox News suicide thing.
Oh, yeah.
That was unbelievable.
Yes.
Also, I guess we did football already. If the Jets suck, then I don't feel like talking about football, and these guys don't really watch, so. Giants lost to the Eagles last night, 1917? Damn.
Yeah, I realize I...
I heard that was a missed field goal to win it for the Giants, right? Is that what happened
Oh,
over
did
there?
They miss a field goal?
I believe so.
What's that going on?
They marched down the field, they had a chance to win, and they missed.
Yeah,
I believe that's how that ended.
I don't know much about football when I tweeted this, that I can't figure out if people are being sarcastic about somebody's prowess on the field. Like when they go, oh, yeah, this guy's great.
That's severe sarcasm.
Suck? Yeah, yeah. When you read the name and it's like, you have no clue?
Yeah.
You don't know anything about it.
Here's how you respond to that. Well, you know, whatever. Yeah, the guy's great.
Yeah.
You know, like that's kind of like, you know, you understand what they're saying, but you know what
he's
doing.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, oh, this guy, oh boy, he sure can catch. Well, oh, can he?
And Arnold was on 60 Minutes. Some good shit there too.
He's got the new book coming out called Total Recall.
His wife's pissed.
It's his memoirs.
Why is his wife pissed?
Because they didn't ask her to comment until the very end.
Right.
And they would not let her see the piece or tell her what Arnold had said.
Nice.
So she's like, I'm not giving a generalized statement just for the piece.
And I hold in my hand. Oh, also we got Katie Sunshine calling in. She has become huge in the last few days.
Oh, man.
That's Hula Hoop Girl.
Yeah.
With everyone else trying to turn us on to a better Hula Hoop Girl. Guess what? You're losing.
Stop it.
She's the real deal, man. She's going to call the show at 7:30.
Nice.
So we'll talk to her about her newfound fame. Although she's been relatively famous, I guess.
Yeah, internet fame.
But now she's really blown up. And a hole in my hand.
Oh, boy.
The first Rocktober.
Rocktober?
You know, there's people around here that aren't fans of Rocktober.
Rocktober? Jocktober.
Oh, I said Rocktober.
Rocktober twice.
Jocktober. Jocktober, of course.
Yeah, I know.
Jocktober.
I know there's people who aren't fans.
I don't give a shit.
No.
I don't really get the Jocktober thing.
We're not talking about listeners, by the way.
No. People that should be in the know. I'm starting off on the right foot, I promise.
Oh, boy.
But it has to be said that it has been said in the past that I don't know. Maybe
I don't get it.
Maybe do it for a couple minutes every other day or so.
No.
But how you guys, I don't really, eating up a lot of time, I don't really.
Do you realize how I fucking love this? 1/12 of a year is fabulous. I wait all year for this.
Yes.
I've been getting tweets for a month.
Yes.
From people saying, 29 days, it's going to be Jocktober.
Jocktober, and we have the first one.
Jocktober, of course, for the people that are new to this show. And it seems like we're getting new people all the time. Mm-hmm. It's a little strange. We just beat the shit out of the entire radio industry for a month straight.
Yeah.
And today we're going to go to Canada to start it all off.
First time ever.
Wow.
First time ever?
I think so.
We've never featured a show from Canada?
Not that I recall.
And this does go hand in hand with Rocktober, because that's the whole thing. When October rolls around, radio guys love calling it Rocktober. October, Rocktober, get it? And the Jocktober thing just kind of carries over, making fun of anybody that would say Rocktober, pretty much. Yeah.
Is this a good show to start it off? You got to start off strong there, Sam.
Oh, yeah. Open big, close big.
I thought this show was a good show. I was surprised Canada's got a lot to offer in terms
of... Oh, boy. Here we go.
Can you promise me we don't feature any fucking shows with guys I know personally?
Oh, no, boy. I cannot promise that.
That I used to do radio with?
You know what I can
promise you? You know, I've tried to strike up a friendship with that guy ever since, and he doesn't want anything to do with me.
Well, have you texted him a couple times?
We used to room together. We started in radio together.
We went to war together. We played golf together.
And I swear, and this is the God's honest truth, Sam brought this show from Nashville last year, and I really was thinking in the back of my head, you know what? The show isn't that bad. It's just not what we do. I really was thinking and I'm not trying to spin it. Uh-huh. But then I felt like I was in the spirit of it, so I was all in like everybody else. But then something didn't seem right. Long story short, it turns out to be a guy that I started radio with in Geneseo.
Yep.
Where we stayed one summer to run the radio station together. And then we ended up rooming together. And then we lost touch over the years, and it's that guy.
That was my favorite moment of last year's Jocktober, because it was like he had just been bashing him, and we were halfway through the segment, and there was some reference to his last name on the clip.
And I tapped out. I knew. I
was and you like, go, wait a minute.
Fuck. But the whole time, I'm like, that voice, something about that voice.
And then you realize that you're in the situation where this guy that you both had the same dream.
Started with.
And
18. 19 years old.
And you're both like, yeah, we're going to do it.
Yeah.
And he's stuck in some small market.
He's in Nashville. He's doing good.
You're a national radio star.
Making fun of him.
And randomly one day, you just decide to start making fun of him for no reason.
But then I'm like, I'm trying to make good. I follow him on Twitter. I comment about his tweets, and he will not follow me.
Does he remark when you comment?
No, man. He doesn't want anything to do with me.
Trying to rebuild that bridge.
Horrible. We started together. We just lost touch over the years.
You know what's great about Jocktober?
Yes.
The listener participation with their various websites and Facebook pages. It's just so much fun to get the listener involved.
Oh, boy.
It really did become a multi-dimensional thing last year.
Yes, it did.
As the listeners became involved and going to Facebook pages. And
oh, boy.
Now, you know what's really fun is that you guys get to stay in New York and Dummy has to go on the road and hear, they won't take you. They were featured on Jocktober.
How many times?
Oh, gosh.
Whoopsie. To count.
Whoopsie.
Yeah. I also like that we still say featured on Jocktober.
Featured.
As if it's an honor to be featured.
Oh, it's great.
It is an honor.
Did you hear? I was featured on Jocktober.
Yeah. You know, I was a featured guest.
Featured.
You know that, I think her name is Terry Clifford in Rochester?
Oh, yeah.
Wheeze gives me Terry Clifford stories all the time.
Oh, no.
Because it's a small town and he runs into her.
Of course he does. She's 600 pounds.
tries to tell me, look, she's really I'm like, I don't care if they're nice people off the air. We had we featured her. She should be proud.
E-Rock would have to double check on the date, but this is either the fourth or the fifth year of Jocktober.
Yeah.
And we have featured Terry Clifford every year. I've insisted.
Is there a strong possibility we feature her again?
I don't like to give any spoilers.
See, in a weird way, it's hard.
Chance.
It's hard to feature new shows because these are now characters. These people,
of course,
and you
got
to see what they've been up to in the past year.
Of course,
have they changed their ways?
Right. And generally speaking, they have not.
They never do.
No. All right. With that said, when we get back, we're gonna start Jocktober with a fine little radio show out of Canada.
We can't announce what station yet.
I know.
Heads up.
None. I know.
None.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very excited.
Do they have a hole?
There's a female on the
show.
Oh,
yeah. Nice!
And I will promise you this. You guys all say that you forget how exhausted you are with the Jocktober segments. Like, you're all excited when they start.
Yeah.
And then within a couple days, you forget how angry and exhausted and furious.
Yes!
My prediction is...
Oh, no.
Exhaustion sets in on day one of Jocktober.
Yes,
you will be tired of this segment today.
All right.
Great.
So there you go. For the people just waking up, your headline is, yes, we did re-sign with SiriusXM for a couple more years.
Ooh.
And after the break, we start Jocktober.
Wow.
Stay there.
It's Jocktober.
This is awesome.
A celebration of rap test radio from around this great nation of ours.
Great.
Thank you. So turn up this turd-tacular radio.
Oh, my God. I can't believe it.
It's
yes.
Jocktober.
Oh, my God. Is it really?
Boy.
Is it really Jocktober?
This has all the features.
Is this really Jocktober?
It's Jocktober.
Oh, God. This is better than Christmas.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
This, I'm just looking at the website. I'm not going to say anything quite yet. But as I look at this, this would be a good parody of a radio show.
Yeah, this can't
it
be real,
it has
right?
all the features. It's got the hole. It's got the old guy, the young buck.
It's got the radio veteran.
Right, the veteran. And the wild guy, but he's wild.
Oh, yeah, he is.
And then that guy. It's got a name that's lame.
Well, that's pretty much the hot format in the country right
now. Is that it?
Oh, yeah. Everyone's going to sports radio.
She keeps everything under control, I bet. Don't let those guys, because that guy, the young buck there, he probably gets crazy. And the old radio veteran and the hole, who, of course, why wouldn't she be overweight? Look at this website, Jimmy. It has all the features. This Jocktober is everything.
And it looks like they all just get along.
Hey, come on. Look at us. There it is.
Where in Canada?
Today.
Ontario. We go to Ontario, Canada, and 94.5, the Bulls.
The Bull!
Bullpen.
It's the morning show, but the Bull is the bullpen.
This gentleman with the salt and pepper hair is Bruffer.
What's Bruffer?
Well, I guess his name is Mike Bruff.
Oh, but they call him the Bruffer.
So he's Bruffer.
Hey, that's like the Opester.
it's the Bruffer.
Hold on. Hey, Kenny, if you're listening, can you keep a list of all these so when I go into markets, we can just check off the ones to tell the club to not try?
Don't bother.
Because that's the most embarrassing part is when you try to get on one that you've jocktobered.
Yeah. Mm.
Gives them a little bit of fucking, a little bit of payback.
Yeah, yeah.
To say no.
Tell you, go fuck yourself.
There's this wild guy that you might know him as Kevin Fell, but in the mornings, he's K-Fell.
K-Fell!
Why K-Fell? K-Fell and the Bruffer?
Because any Kevin, it becomes a K. Yeah.
And of course, Janice McKay, a.k.a. Mac.
Oh, they got some nice names, right?
They got the good names.
Bruffer, Mac, and K-Fell.
Oh, yeah.
94.5, the Bull.
You're listening to the bullpen. Hey, Mac! Ugh. Hey, what's going on?
Do they have sound effects of a ball hitting a bat?
Oh,
not that I heard, no.
Okay. Do they have a, like a bull? That'd be good.
A little bit of that.
Oh,
a little bit of
that. Jesus, I'm guessing here.
All right. Well, we got Katie Sunshine calling in a few minutes, so we should get a couple clips from this show on for
wet
Jocktober.
Our tootsies a little in this wonderfulness of Jocktober.
All right, Jocktober has begun with the bullpen with Bruffer, Mac, and K-Fell on Ontario, Canada's 94.5 The Bull.
That's right.
Wendell Clark, the hockey player, is calling in later, and K-Fell has a totally crazy idea. I love Jocktober.
Oh, I've been waiting all year.
It's a big guest for the show.
I think this is the only reason we re-signed with Sirius.
Just because we knew.
Like, we have to do Jocktober.
Is that what they did? Management was like, listen, guys.
Right.
You know Jocktober is Monday. You don't have to re-sign, but...
That's why we have a one-month deal.
Listen, Wendell Clark is like, they're very excited about this guest. Now, K-Fell is known to get a little...
K-Fell's the crazy guy.
A little rambunctious.
I don't want to confuse him with Mac.
Right. No, Mac is I'm glad Mac's there.
Yeah.
Because what she does is she lets things go to a certain level, but when it's time to keep things under control.
Thank God.
You think she has an actual yield and stop sign in the studio?
Yeek.
Here we go.
The Rock Station 94.5, the Bull Rock and South Huron at 91.7. We may have Wendell Clark on the show today. We're giddy like school kids, I'm telling you, Mac. Are you
I'm
all
excited.
Hepped up too?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you are too. Good.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Because Mac's just excited because this could be the first time in her life she ever sees me speechless.
I can't wait.
Hi, Wendell.
Oh, I hope that happens. I'll get to ask all the questions.
I'll be like Chris Farley.
Hopefully.
Do a Chris Farley on him. He'd probably appreciate that. Wendell's got a great sense of humor, by the way.
Remember when you fought McSorley?
Do it. I dare you. Double dog. You won't do it. You're chicken.
Double dog?
Oh, my God.
He's chicken.
I swear to God, you would think this was an SNL parody.
Oh,
this is real shit.
Hey. What a radio voice, though, huh?
I like that burrito.
Hey. He sounds like nearly 1,000 people I've heard on the radio.
That's all you hear.
That's all you hear.
It's just a rhythm.
Awesome.
And K-Fell, he wants to do, you know, the Chris Farley thing.
Well, that's crazy.
Should
I say cray-cray? That's cray-cray.
You could. But Bruffer is there to be like, you're a little chicken. You'll never do it.
Yeah, you're a chicken. But Nova Scotia's, thank God Mac's there.
Nova Scotia's pissed. Ontario's a province. All right, whatever.
Whatever.
I just look at it as one big state.
What is that? Stop it, Canada.
Washington, Ontario.
D.C. is a District of Columbia.
Exactly.
Shut up.
So what do we got, a double dog dare or something going down
here?
That's
right. He double dog dares and he won't do it. He's chicken.
What did you want him to do?
I don't know. You know, I forgot already.
The Chris Farley skit where he goes, remember when you did this? That was awesome.
Oh, during the interview with McCartney?
Yeah.
It's very funny, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, it was funny.
Well, he's saying that when Wendell Clark calls in, he's going to do the Chris Farley.
Ah.
And then Bruffer goes, I double dog dare you. And then he goes, you won't do it. You're chicken.
He didn't really say double dog dare you.
Oh, well, we could go and check the end of the clip.
He didn't really say that.
Certainly did.
I won't hold you to this one, though. All right. I will not hold you to this one.
Wow.
No, I will. Mac, hold him down.
Clip two.
No, you got to be nuts.
Oh, boy. Boy, they sound like a lot of fun, though.
That's the thing.
He'd probably appreciate that. Wendell's got a great sense of humor, by the way.
Remember when you fought McSorley?
Do it, I dare you, double dog. You won't do it, you're chicken.
Double dog. Double dog.
I dare you, double dog.
Double dog.
That's serious.
Wow, double dog dares are pretty rough.
No, double dog. It was Mac and her sister were in the studio at the time.
I mean, that's the type of thing that K-Fal thinks to himself. I'm kind of pinned up against a wall here. Yeah. I really got to go through with this crazy prank.
Well, when do we get to hear the Wendell Clark?
I didn't even bother with it. He didn't do it. I
mean, of course.
Oh, he just didn't do it?
It was an interview with a hockey player. He didn't
really?
Do it. No, of course not.
Yeah, because we got to let people know this is like all the highlights of one show.
This is one day.
Right. So they got to the Wendell Clark and it was just nothing? It was a who gives a fuck interview?
Yes, of course it was.
So he lost a double dare?
He lost a double dog
dare?
Yeah.
Double dog dare?
But he didn't do what he said he was going to do?
No, Bruffer was right. He was chicken.
Double dog.
Yeah. These guys are fucking good.
Ah, you like them, Chip?
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. They're
just really fun, good. Right?
No yeah, everybody's just joking around.
So I guess we just got to move on, huh?
That's it.
That was it for the Wendell Clark thing?
Coverage.
K-Fell agrees to do something based on a Prepburger news story. Remember Prepburger, people? We like to educate the audience as well as beat the shit out of everyone. Prepburger is a service where you could subscribe to, and they'll give you your jokes every morning.
Yeah,
they're not good enough to come up with their own jokes.
Are they still in existence?
The whole
Prepburger?
Industry.
Yeah.
Whole industry, yeah.
They make parodies for you.
Nice. Topical humor, right?
They have topical humor. They actually have answers. We did it one year.
Right.
They have answers to interviews.
Nice.
So you could pretend like we did it with, like, Alan Alda, I think.
Oh, can we do that again this year?
Sure, we could find it.
There's so much we got to do for this Jocktober feature. Right.
But they also have, like, the wacky news stories of the day.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you start flipping around radio stations and you realize they're all talking about the same wacky news stories.
Right.
It's because they're not even researching.
Yeah. How is it that you go on the radio and have a radio show and you can't come up with your own shit?
I don't know. A lot of radio shows do it, though.
A lot of them.
Prepburger.
And that's really, like, Prepburger. People go, it's harmless. It's just helping people have fun. But it's just, it's helping uncreative and lazy people seem funny. And it's like, there's a lot of really funny and creative people that could probably go on and do this job if they were given a chance.
What happened?
Uh-oh, I'm seeing...
what happened?
This is not good.
What happened?
I'm at their Facebook page.
Oh.
They're on Facebook.
Right. Yeah.
And there's a picture of, I don't know, the Bruffer and K-Fell with somebody, I guess a hockey player or something. And the comment is, today's your day, shit fox.
Today's your day.
Nice.
And, you know, you can go through their wall.
Well, people are pissed. There's no Facebook for the bull.
No, there.
Yeah, but you're reading off their Facebook page. I don't know if we can. Should we?
Yeah, I mean, if you go
we'll
to the,
find it.
If you Google the station.
Yeah, we don't really encourage.
Of course not.
To take over the Facebook pages. If it happens, we can't. You know, we can't control it.
I do think it's funny, but I.
All I did was Google the station and then click the thing that says Facebook.
Oh look, Fatty Pig Fatty has Paul Hargis's birthday wish up there. Oh, that's a good one.
There's a picture of a jack-o'-lantern with a woman sucking a man's dick on the jack-o'-lantern.
Instead of the eyes and nose and
it's pretty
mouth.
Good. A big fat lump of shit trying to get into her jeans.
This is not good. It says there's a picture by somebody claiming to be Sam Roberts. It's a fake.
Fake Sam Roberts.
Sam Roberts Facebook page. Yeah. It says, like if you love Jesus, ignore for devil, and it's a picture of an apple with legs and a lot of pubic hair and a giant penis coming out of his underwear.
Coming out of it. So the listeners have started. Oh, God.
There's a big black man having sex with what appears to be an inflatable purple pigeon.
Yeah.
All right. Well, why don't we get on to the next clip here, and then we're going to talk to Katie Sunshine.
Oh, boy.
K-Fell agrees to do something based on a Prepburger news story. What's that there, Sam? Without reading the story, what does that mean?
Yeah, it's like they had this Prepburger news story that they wanted to get to. And
was it wacky news?
It's wacky. The news story is a little crazy.
Okay.
But you want to talk about crazy. KFEL agrees to do something without even knowing what the article says.
That's insane.
And it's like, you know, it's one thing to dip your foot in the water, but if you're just going to dive in without checking, that's the kind of guy he is, though.
That's the kind of guy he is.
KFEL's a little edgy?
Oh, yeah.
Morning madness.
You think he's a little unpredictable?
He is. That's the thing. All right. He's nuts.
And then what'd you say? Luckily, Mac is there as things drift out of control.
Oh, yeah, if you listen to the whole, towards the end of the clip, things start to go a little crazy. So thank God there's somebody to keep it in line.
All right, you may be checking to do this,
although you agreed to do this before you knew any of the information here.
Which I really have to stop doing.
Yeah, I know you do have to stop.
Oh, my God. What the fuck kind of delivery does he have?
He's crazy, Ann. I told you, like he's Bobcat. Right. He just, I really have to stop doing that. He's got no gauge on when he's supposed to sell the emotion. He's just like, I just start screaming now. Like, there's no reason for him to be that upset.
He might be channeling Chris Farley. Well, we all love Chris Farley, right?
He's explaining why things are so out of control. He's like, gotta stop doing these things. Yeah. He's basically saying, I gotta look before I leap.
And if we believe the premise of what's happening, he doesn't know what the news story is yet, so... He doesn't even know if he should be upset.
Right. It could be something good.
But this is him on a regular day.
Yeah, it's crazy.
You may be checking to do this, although you agreed to do this before you knew any of the information here.
Which I really have to stop doing.
Yeah, I know you do have to stop doing that. This is great news, though. Scientists have figured out a way for men to live longer. Not women.
Yeah.
Men.
I don't have to change anything about the way I live
now.
Well,
that's sexist.
No, you don't have to change a thing.
There's the women's point of view.
The whole.
Well, that's sexist.
Yeah, why would she make a joke there?
Exactly.
Why not just jump in? Like, everyone's laughing, and all of a sudden she puts a picture of a tumor on the table. Way to be fun.
That's sexist.
Oh, God.
Anything about the way I live
now.
Well,
that's sexist.
No, you don't have to change a thing about the way you live right now.
You already live longer.
Oh.
You have to have your package cut off, though.
No.
Oh.
Like, right off?
Yes.
Like, which part of the package? The whole deal? Yeah. What's going on there?
Like, the twig and giggleberries gone.
All of it?
Gone. Yeah, scientists.
He didn't say that. Please.
I know, it's regular radio.
And KFEL is not
afraid.
He
didn't say that.
I definitely got to, like, chill on that one.
Who says that?
No one.
The giggle berries.
The twig and giggle.
Even when we had to like work around some rules, we came up with junk a long time ago.
Twig and giggle berries.
You think when they're doing an appearance somewhere, some like five people in a bar, some guy will come up and go, "Hey, how's your twig and giggle berries?" Like, "Hey, I listen."
Maybe they have bumper stickers that refer to the three of them as the twig and giggle berries.
Nice. Yee.
Right off?
Yes.
Like, which part of the package? The whole deal? Yeah. What's going on there?
Like, the twig and giggleberries gone.
All of it?
Gone. Yeah. Scientists have studied genealogy records of ancient Korea and found that men who were castrated lived an average of 14 to 19 years longer than men who got to keep their stones.
That's weird.
Listen.
But maybe that's just because then you don't have the same testosterone levels and stuff.
See, this would change nothing.
And then you don't get into fights and die.
Well,
you don't use it anyway.
I don't use it, but I'd like to keep it around just in case.
I love when you agree to stuff before you find the deal. I won't hold you to this one, though. All right. I will not hold you to this one.
Wow.
No, I will. Mac, hold him down.
No, you gotta be nuts.
What's going on? That sounds just like Amy Schumer when she did the voice for Louis. That's exactly like that.
And Bruffer was actually asking her to hold down their sidekick while he castrates him.
While he cuts his dick and balls off, and she was like, no!
Yeah, it was important for Mac to say no, because otherwise they would have castrated a man live in the studio.
You think they would have went through it?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
That's not what I tune in the bullpen for in the morning. I tune in for some fun, a couple of laughs, maybe something interesting.
But there's all these dares, and there's no payoff to their dares.
You're chicken. He keeps calling them chicken.
They're all for two.
You guys have been in radio for a long time.
We sure have, Sam.
Do you think that they really did, during the commercial break, say, listen, KFEL, you got to promise to do it? And KFEL was like, look, I don't know, but I'll do it.
Yep,
I will.
Yep,
right.
Absolutely.
You think so?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, just go along with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't worry. In the end, you don't have to be castrated, but let's go along with it. We can have a little fun with this, I think.
God.
KFEL sounds a little bit like Chris Griffin, too.
Oh, yeah. A little bit.
Oh, he's trying so hard to be a character.
Well, we got to hold on with Jocktober because we got Katie Sunshine on the line.
Ah.
So there's a little taste of Jocktober as we kick it off today with the bullpen with Bruffer, Mac, and Kayfell.
And there's
Canada's 94.5 The Bull.
There's a lemon party going on their Facebook page.
But let's talk to Katie Sunshine, then we'll get back to Jocktober. Katie.
Give us a visual.
Hi, Katie.
Hi, how are you?
Oh, well, hi there.
We are much better. I feel like I'm talking to a huge celebrity.
Oh, thank you.
We discovered you because of the video that was done at WinFest.
Yes, yes.
Who filmed that?
My husband actually filmed
it. Damn it!
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm speaking for the entire audience.
Yeah, you really are.
Your husband.
Oh, thank you. Well, I thought he was just taking my picture, and so I just kept pausing and smiling because I thought I was posing for a picture. I didn't know he was taking a video of it.
Right. Oh, really?
We were wondering, because we've watched this. I've gone over this more than people went over the Zapruder film, and I noticed that like a lot of the guys aren't looking at you, and we all wondered why, and then I speculated, I bet you that there's a big guy filming her, and that's why the men aren't stopping just to stare, because there's a man filming, so...
Well, my husband has a very large beard, and so that could be part of the reason.
What kind of guy is he?
He's a really nice guy. He's a pretty big guy, but I really think the reason was I've been doing that all day.
Oh, so really?
They were used to seeing me.
I would never get used to seeing that. I would be staring at you the entire time. There's guys with a blue cooler in the background. They don't care.
When I first started hula hooping that day, I would have a few people gather around me, but like I said, I had hours by that point. So they're just like, oh, there's the hula hoop girl again.
You've done a lot of videos, huh?
Yes, quite a few.
But this one seems to have really taken off. This one's going everywhere.
Yeah, and I don't really know why, because I didn't do any editing. I didn't dress up in any costumes.
That's the beauty of it. The yoga pants, you got to be kidding me.
Maybe that's it. Maybe it's the tight pants.
You don't realize you're a very good-looking woman?
Well...
And that you can move very nicely.
Well, I just love hula hooping. I love...
You love hula hooping.
How long... And you've made me love it. How long have you been hula hooping?
I've been hula hooping for about 4 years now.
Oh.
That's it?
Mm-hmm.
Usually, you know, you're a kid when you start that.
Well, I could hula hoop when I was a kid. And, you know, like most adults, at some point you just stop. You don't hula hoop anymore. Mm. And then I picked it up when I was about, I don't know, 22, 23. Okay. And I had completely forgotten how to hula hoop around the waist.
Yeah.
I was just doing a little math.
Yeah.
She's perfect.
Now, are you from Arkansas originally?
I am. I was born and raised in Arkansas.
But now you live in the Philly area?
No, I still live in Arkansas. I'm just a Phillies fan and an Eagles fan.
Yeah, so...
Ah.
How did that... Oh, I love this guy. Hold on. That fucking drunk.
The guy who just drunkenly sings to you and walks away.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and he was totally singing the wrong song, too.
Yeah, he...
No,
he
we know that. He was singing a little Neil Young for everybody.
Yeah.
Wait, so how do you become a Phillies Eagles fan if you're from Arkansas?
Well, I became a Phillies fan because I've got a huge crush on Chase Utley. And then I became an Eagles fan when some other Eagles fans sent me all the gear to make the Eagles hula hoop video.
Right.
They just contacted me. They said, you know, if we send you this stuff, will you do a hula hoop video in our gear? And I was like, sure, of course. So, and then we started talking back and forth, and they were so nice. Ended up being an Eagles fan, too.
There you go.
Wow.
And you're a school teacher, right?
I am. I teach art. I'm the elementary art teacher at my school.
Oh, good God.
That's adorable.
God, when I took art in school, I didn't have a teacher like you.
Do you notice
I think mine was half a fruit. I believe he was making dresses for Cher. I think. No, he actually was, but I think he... Yeah, whatever.
Do the fathers... has any like parents commented on these videos to you?
Yeah.
Not many have seen my videos that I know of, but I hula hoop for the kids sometime at the school, so they all know I hula hoop.
Oh.
I don't know if they've seen my videos. I try not to advertise those too much at school.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'm sure eventually some idiot will have a problem with your videos at school.
Yeah, I'm sure. That's kind of, I've been holding my breath for that, but so far nothing bad has happened.
Hey, why do you have such a crappy backyard?
I really don't.
Do you need some money for landscaping? Because we're distracted by the burnt out grass in some of your videos.
Oh, I know. It is bad. I know. I've been hoping that I could get accepted maybe onto one of those shows where, you know, the people come in and they totally remodel your backyard.
Well, they'll do that for you. Are you getting calls from, like, Hollywood or anything? Any talk shows, anything?
I've been getting a lot of emails from, like, clip shows. That want to use my clip and, I don't know, make fun of it, I guess. Probably make fun of my backyard.
Well, like who? Who's been calling you?
There was one show called Clipaholics, and I was on that show. They used my clip, and they did like a little history of the hula hoop segment, and basically they just zoomed in on my boobs and my butt. It was
Oh, boy. They used you. They used you for your assets.
That is a selling point, though.
It is a selling point, but we do like the whole package there, Katie.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
You really hula hoop well.
Yeah, you got some of those wacky moves, you know?
Thanks.
I like the shoulder one. That's a good trick where you spin it on your shoulder.
Uh-huh.
And then I like the other one where you just kind of hold it. And move it up and down.
You must drive your neighbors crazy. We're looking at the one where you're in your front yard. It's got to be a lot of guys peeking through their windows as you film this stuff.
Yeah, wearing white puffy boots, all sexy, little shorts.
You know, there's a guy across the street just losing his mind.
Of course.
I know. That's the big joke, is there's no telling what my neighbors think of me.
I could guess what they're thinking.
Yeah, if you
it's
need
all
to know.
Good.
Yeah.
I think we can figure that out for you.
How's the marriage going?
It's great. We have been married for about a year and a half, but we've been together forever. We dated for 7 years before we got married.
Oh, okay. I was hoping there might be some struggles.
Struggle.
Our whole audience is hoping
struggles.
Yeah.
Sorry, no struggles.
So now, what do you want to do? Do you want to teach school, or is this something else you want to do, like in the creative field?
Well, really, art has been my passion my entire life. If I could do anything, it would just be paint all day and sell my paintings for $10,000 a piece.
Where are your paintings? Are they online anywhere?
Yes, I have them on my Katie Sunshine Facebook page.
Wow, you do. Let's look at your paintings. Let's see how good it is.
Yeah, I didn't...
What does your husband do for a living?
He is an undercover narcotics officer.
Ah, shit.
Which translates into a really tough dude.
Wow.
Yeah, he's going to fucking break some teeth.
Yeah, big narc with a beard. That guy's a problem.
Exactly. He's a problem.
Do you worry about him doing that line of work?
Am I worried about him?
Do you worry about that line of work? That's a rough one.
Not really. I worry about him sometimes, but for the most part, he's pretty competent, so.
Okay.
I like your painting of the trees with the leaves changing.
Oh, thank you.
I really do, actually.
Thanks.
It's not bad at all. What's your Facebook page so people could check this shit out, too?
All right, great.
No, what is your Facebook page?
What is the page?
What is the page?
Yeah.
It's just search for Katie Sunshine.
Okay.
Hey, you did something with the Philly Fanatic on the dugout.
Yes, that was so much fun.
We interviewed him many years ago. Did you notice how poorly the outfit smelled on him?
No, I didn't notice, actually.
Oh,
maybe
you should've.
Because I was so nervous to be up there in front of all those people.
Were you afraid you were going to drop your hula hoop?
It was kind of drizzling that day, and they asked me, they said, are you sure you can still do this? Because the top of the dugout gets kind of slippery when it gets wet. And I was like, oh, shit. I'm going to get up there and slip and fall off the dugout and... Everybody in the stadium is going to have a video of it, and then it's going to be everywhere on the internet. That's what I was afraid of.
You did great, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I was so glad I didn't back out, because I was so nervous.
But if you fell, it would have been a great video, though. I mean, even though this is hot, there would have been a very funny video, a hot girl falling with a hula hoop into the dugout.
Were any guys yelling things at you?
There were. I could hear some cheers, and I could hear some whistles, but I couldn't really hear anybody yelling anything at me.
How annoyed were you that that big, fat, green thing had to dance next to you and try to get attention for itself while you're up there doing something really good?
Philly fanatic.
She's too nice. Katie Sunshine is just too
nice. Katie Sunshine is just a nice lady.
You're just nice.
Thank you.
We don't know how to handle people that are just nice people.
A nice elementary school teacher.
Yeah.
You got to deal with the kids.
What age do you teach?
I teach kindergarten all the way up to sixth grade.
Sure.
Wow.
Nice.
Do you want to have kids of your own?
I don't know. I have a stepson. My husband has a son.
Okay.
So he's, you know, he's kind of been my kiddo. I don't know if we'll ever have any kids around or not.
How old is he, your stepson?
He just turned 14.
Oh, my God.
Does he love you?
Oh, my God. Stepson.
Well, I think, I don't know. I use the hula hoop thing as, like, blackmail. You know, I think I'm always threatening to show up to one of his events with all his friends there. And
stuff. Oh, yeah, that would be terrible.
Yeah.
What? They must love, his friends must absolutely
What's
love
that
you.
That kid, it's just mom.
Yeah, I want to go over your house.
Yeah, how many? Yeah, exactly.
Can we go over your house today?
I bet you he brings a lot of friends over to your house.
Well, he lives with his mama. In Mountainburg, which is about 2 hours from us. Jesus. So we see him. He's pretty far away. We see him on the weekends and in the summertime and spring break and all that good stuff.
All right. Well, Katie, we're glad we got to talk to you.
Yes, you're lovely, like we figured you'd be. A nice lady.
Oh, thank you. Well, thank you so much for having me on.
No problem. Any other interviews or what?
No, I haven't had nothing I know of yet.
I sent your video to Jimmy Fallon. I said, yo, Jimmy, get her on.
Oh, thank you.
Well, nothing happened. But I tried for you. I would put this on a talk show in a second.
Yeah, we too.
In a second.
Well, thank you, guys.
Well, look, and if things don't work out, you know, marriage can be tough. There are other options. I just wanted you to know that.
How about this?
Thanks for looking out for me.
Katie, how about we give you some Opie and Anthony t-shirts and you make a little video for us? Just a little one.
I would love to.
Yeah.
That'd be nice. Put up on the site.
Yeah, put it on the site. And I think our fans would love that.
Yes, I think so too.
Yeah. I like the yoga pants, but I do like the cutoff shorts too.
Yes. Well, I talked about in the Eagles hoop video.
Yep.
Yeah, I said, you guys just have to send me a jersey and some boots. I said, I've got the cutoff. I'm an Arkansas girl. Well, everybody has those here.
Well, we're gonna cut the shirt down a little bit, if you know what I mean. A little bit.
Okay.
All right, hold on the line, Katie.
All right, I will. Thank you.
Thank you, Katie.
Katie Sunshine, everyone, from the hula hoop video.
She's just nice.
She's very nice.
She's like...
She's exactly really how I figured nice. She'd be. That's just a really? Yeah, and a really nice...
That's like an innocence tour.
Because she's a school teacher. It's like you're not gonna. She's not gonna come on and be dirty or bitchy as a school teacher.
Right. But then she's got a few of those what you call provocative moves.
Yeah.
When she's doing that hula hoop.
You think? You think she knows she has some provocative moves?
Yeah.
She knows how to play it just right. Because she knows those kids' parents are gonna possibly check out these videos eventually.
Yeah. So she's gotta be.
Like she bends over, but she's like, no, I'm not bending over to show my hiney. I got to bend over to keep the hula hoop rotating.
That's pretty provocative right there. She's in a black leather skirt. She's got those giant leopard boots on.
Oh, she's fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a light. It's two light-up hula hoops.
But you can't see
her. So.
See, that's not smart.
Yeah, nobody wants to see lighted hula hoops.
Nah.
Yeah.
I only want to see her.
Right. What? Oh, there. Okay, now she's off. So.
Look, I'm not wiggling my hiney. I got to keep the hula hoop going.
Yeah, it's just part of the, you know.
yeah.
Part of the video.
Oh, I am bending over, but oops, I got to get the hula hoop back up my body.
Yeah. Oh, there it is. That's that move. When it's around her ankles, and then she's got to get it back up, she really moves. Yeah.
No, I'm not wiggling real fast to show off my ass. I got to get the hula hoop off the ground, everyone.
Fantastic.
Just bludgeoning her ample breast scissors.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she's a sensation.
Yeah, she really is.
I'm really surprised she hasn't done any shows yet. She will. takes a little time with this shit, right?
She's lovely.
So a fucking narcotics, undercover narcotics cop.
She couldn't have mentioned a fucking tougher guy job.
Exactly.
I was hoping he would do something really fruity. What does he do? He's a shoe salesman.
Yes. He's a floral arranger.
Yes.
He's a party planner.
No, I've seen a photo of him and them together.
Oh,
and,
yeah?
Yeah, he's a big fucking dude, man.
Oh, you've done some studying, huh, Jimmy?
Research.
Backed off immediately.
Oh, man.
Said, all right.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. There's Katie Sunshine.
Very nice.
And we're going to break, and we're going to get back to Jocktober. That's what we do today.
Yeah.
All right?
All right.
All right.
Serious accents. The Opie and Anthony Show.
I want to thank Katie Sunshine for calling the show. I think we're going to send some Wow and Opie and Anthony shit so she can do a hula hoop video for us. Mm. It's got to be the best one she does, though, right? So we got to figure out how to make it better than the ones that are up there.
Man.
She's just a nice lady.
Really?
Shouldn't say lady. I mean, she's
honestly
a woman. She's very nice, though. What the fuck is that?
There's a picture of a man cow with Bobo.
What? Where did that come from?
On the B94 The Bull Facebook page.
Oh, somebody. Okay.
I didn't know he did man cow.
We're going to, back to Jocktober.
Jocktober.
Let's do this.
So, Jocktober.
It begins today. The whole month we feature radio shows from around the country and Canada. And Canada.
And Canada this year. This is special.
It is special. The first show ever featured
and Canadian,
on Jocktober from Canada.
Canadian listeners have been asking for it for a long time.
They have.
Oh, yeah. They have Jocktober going on there, too.
The Bullpen with Bruffer, Mac, and Kayfell. That's what we're talking about today.
Of course.
94.5 The Bull, Ontario, Canada.
Ontario,
yeah? Yes. There Ontario.
Is, I'm sure people want recognition for it, too. There is evidence of Hulk Hogan causing the collapse of the World Trade Center.
Wait, where's the one picture? Oh, there it is. Wait, where are you going? I did this for you.
That is so stupid.
Hey, wait. Like, he just totally didn't read the situation right.
No.
Wait, I did this for you. This where are you going?
I like how he's doing his poses in the wreckage.
See, other people look at that picture like he's the evil one. I don't.
No.
I see it as, wait, what happened?
Where are you going?
I did this for you.
He dropped the big boot on Tower 2.
Oh, he certainly did.
Fast forward, did you ever think we would be laughing at Hulk Hogan,
anything,
Hulk Hogan
to do with that,
and Twin Tower pictures?
No.
But
well, hilarious.
It's on, obviously, 94.5 The Bolt thinks it's funny because it's on their Facebook
page. Oh, it's on their Facebook page.
Right?
He's hitting the chair. That's my favorite. That chair.
It's just so wrong.
Huge chair.
Yeah. All right, let's get into another clip from The Bullpen. Thank God Prepburger had some more wacky news.
Ah.
Yeah.
Where we replace punchlines with awkward laughing. What's this about, Sam?
Well, sometimes, you know, the point is you read the wacky news story and you can come up with your own little jokes and stuff.
Sure.
Or you could just read the news story, pause where there would normally be a punchline, and just kind of laugh.
Ugh. All right.
Well, let's play it, all right?
Yeah, let's.
6:39, Bruffer, Mac, and Kayfell into Tuesday. Welcome to the Bullpen. Partly sunny today. High to 21, 12 degrees right
now. Oh, God. The weather is over.
Who needs a radio station to tell you the fucking weather in this day and age?
And I was sitting in my house Saturday morning, and I'm watching local news, and they spent 5 minutes on the weather. I'm like, could someone tell these people we don't get our fucking weather from TV anymore?
Useless.
I mean,
weather.
Maybe the 5-day forecast. Put that up on the screen for 10 seconds.
I could get
tops.
That online. It's just. Whoop.
I know, but why would you spend 5 fucking minutes describing the weather? Still,
no need.
I would assume this is one of their listeners because it's on their Facebook page.
Yeah.
They post the weather on their Facebook page too.
Oh, nice.
Good thing.
And they write today: partly to mostly sunny, high 17, winds west 10 to 20.
Fuck, it's cold up there.
High 17.
Yeah.
Well, that's Celsius shit.
And one of their listeners comments with a 100% chance of AIDS.
That's a very, very bad weather condition.
Terrible.
I'd hate to have a 100% chance of AIDS in the air.
Penn, partly sunny today, high to 21, 12 degrees right now at the Bull. Newport, Tennessee. I don't know, you guys decide, is it gonna be a second date after this?
After what?
Dawn Peters arrested, charged with aggravated assault after she allegedly, I say, hit 51-year-old William L. Wolford on the head with a hammer at least 5 times while they were having sex.
Nailed him.
Yes. That's right.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Holy fuck.
Oh, shit.
And of course, the Chris Griffin guy has to laugh because he's the edgy guy. He finds everything like that funny, right?
Because normally it's like if somebody getting hit in the head with a hammer is so dangerous. That's not funny, but not for KFL.
This whole thing, I could listen to that segment 10 times just to get every nuance. The way he goes into the story is terrible.
Mm-hmm.
It just hey, I'm just conversing.
Yeah.
And then the hammer line, and then nailed, which is the double entendre of fucking.
Yeah. There might be a couple more double entendres.
Oh, boy.
Thunder Scoot, one of my regulars, someone's got to get this. He just sent me a headline that says, being bullied, ? Just act less gay, advise teachers.
There you go.
That's all you got to do. Those teachers are in trouble?
I think they're in a little bit of trouble there.
Fucking Thunder Scoot, where'd you find that article? I want to read the whole fucking thing later.
Hey, you think, what did she cave, did she cave his ball sack in with that hammer? Did he turn around and smash her cunt?
I think it's funny when he says twig and giggleberry, though.
You still on that chip?
That's hilarious. My mother would always say, Chipper, stop waving your twig and giggleberries. Lamar's going to see you.
Lamar's the one that did your mom?
No, he was helping her.
Yeah, helping her with the floor.
Oh, these guys are funny. Why he would be in your house like that.
He fixes the rug.
Ah.
Why is your hand in your pants, Chip?
It's touching my twig.
With a hammer. At least 5 times while they were having sex.
Nailed him.
Yes. Right.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Gives a whole new meaning to she nailed him anyway.
And they were in the living room doing this.
Yeah, I know. That's what she said.
He just did her joke.
I know. That's sort of what she said. And he reacted to that like, whoa, that's crazy. You got a whole
new meaning to the word nailed him.
You understood before, though, Opie. A little bit. KFL came and explained that.
A little bit.
Yeah, imagine if they did something totally bad, like, nailed him, like Jesus on that cross.
Yeah.
The PD's running down the hall, freaking out.
Yeah, he just said something funny like, a hammer? What, was he raping a child or something?
Chip. Man. Come on.
Sex.
Oh. Nailed him.
Nailed him, right.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Gives a whole new meaning to she nailed him anyway.
And they were in the living room doing this, too.
Good.
Nice. I guess she really knows how to handle him.
I guess she does.
Maybe he liked it rough.
Apparently, during sex, she picked up a hammer for no apparent reason. She nailed him on the head 5 times.
Yeah, I know. You said that.
And then she runs out of the residence in a French maid outfit. And get this. I don't even understand how this made the story. That she'd apparently purchased at Walmart.
I know. What? It's a cheap one. That's all we know.
Oh, wow. They had nothing.
We got to start saying Walmart more.
Yeah.
It gets laughs. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
They had nothing
the
there.
Show a little more.
The one thing that this trio has is chemistry, if nothing else.
They really do, Sam.
Yeah, like bleach and ammonia. You know what I noticed? The handle line was another hammer joke. Oh. She was thinking that people would knows how to handle them. Like, she's just trying to go through parts of a hammer
and find puns.
And there's only 3 parts to a hammer. The hammerhead, the handle, and the little wedge that keeps them both together.
Or the claw.
Other than
that, the claw?
Well, that's the whole head part.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's a separate part.
That's a whole other joke.
If you want to start breaking down the claw, you could have fucking done thalidomide baby jokes. They got that dumb claw, you know?
Fucking that dumb claw. We squeeze a few more jokes out of that news story before getting to the unscientific survey.
A little daily feature.
All right.
On the bullpen.
The survey.
Now, she's 31, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, if he's not going to call her back, I wouldn't mind her number.
Give her a ring.
Yeah, maybe he was a real tool.
What happened?
She's just trying.
What happened?
She's fucking puns 101.
The real tool.
She got another one in.
Yeah.
Wow. But none of us could figure out the tool.
No.
That's right.
She did get the tool thing.
And you see how the crazy one wants her number?
Yeah, so he can call her.
Watch out, everyone.
He's wild.
I'm not afraid of her.
He would like to date her.
I bet he never saw that coming.
Right. That's another.
Yeah.
See?
Saw? Ha ha, seesaw.
I wonder if she said, stop hammer time.
Right, we heard you with the puns. Fucking.
I mean, if he's not going to call her back, I wouldn't mind her number.
Give her a ring.
Yeah, maybe he was a real tool.
I mean, she sounds like a delight on a first date.
Yeah, she sure does.
Yeah.
So, on scientific survey question, it is back for a second day because nobody answered directly yesterday.
Oh, my God. Wow, that's a hell of a segue.
Yeah, you got a new. The humor was all wrapped up. It's just before it's too much.
They've minded for enough jokes.
Yeah. Like,
minded. Nice.
Leave them wanting more. Exactly.
Right.
We hit the pinnacle of this pyramid before we start going down the other side.
Yeah.
Let's move on to the next hilarious thing.
Yeah.
A survey question?
Yeah, the unscientific survey is there. This is something a lot of radio shows don't do anymore.
Can you imagine if we could get away with a survey question that takes 2 days to answer?
Oh, my God.
How great our jobs would be?
Oh, my God.
Well, the reason it took them 2 days to answer is they say nobody had the correct answer.
No one gave a shit.
Nobody called in.
Well, the question was, what is the worst radio show in Canada?
And they just didn't want to.
Yeah, they wanted one different answer.
Stop calling us.
How's their Facebook page going?
Not great. We're in phase two. Phase one, we passed, which was deleting comments.
They started deleting
phase
comments.
Phase one is acknowledgement.
Acknowledgement.
Slash
deleting comments.
Delete the shit out of our Facebook page.
Right. Phase two.
What is phase two? Yes.
Is defense, which is blocking users.
Yeah, a lot of people are bummed out. I checked my Twitter. They're bummed. They got blocked. And they're like, man, I was on a roll. Why did they block me?
Are these guys on Twitter too?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they are.
They are?
They're all over
the
place.
What is phase three? Have we ever gotten to phase three?
We've gotten to...
Isn't phase three where they completely remove the phase?
Yeah, that's...
I think we've had a couple of those.
We've had most of these have gone through to phase three, which is... Removal of Facebook.
Remove their page. Yeah. I love phase three.
It's just not stopping. I mean, you have now Jerry Shepardini.
Oh, Jerry Shepardini.
Who's chiming in with
this. Oh, my God.
What was a prolapse?
And Jerry Shepardini is chiming in with the joke. Hammer, what is this, a child rape or something?
These fucking assholes.
Jerry Shepardini.
So, I mean,
well, let's get to the scientific survey.
Yeah,
question. It is back for a second day because nobody answered directly yesterday. More than a third of men made themselves look stupid while attempting to impress a woman doing this. What is it, guys? And some of the most popular answers yesterday, dancing. Actually,
yeah,
dancing
because
was the big one.
All of us look a little silly dancing, don't we?
Well,
I think I know this one.
Listen.
Jerking off over a cracker? shitting their pants. Farting in her face. faking their own death. Guys have tried to impress a woman by doing
impress
this.
Impress a woman by doing this.
But it's a scientific survey?
Unscientific.
Oh, fuck.
I was thinking scientific.
Somebody just posted Twig and Giggleberries for the win.
Twig and Giggleberries.
For the win. As in, that joke was so good.
You've
won the day.
You think they hate that we're focusing on them today?
Hate it.
They're very distracted and off their game right now?
Yeah.
Hey, there's no worse news for a terrestrial radio show than today you're being featured on Jocktober.
No worse.
Because they all know about it, too.
The next,
I hear from radio friends from around the country, and they're like, fuck, dude. Everyone knows about this Jocktober thing.
The next 31 days is just a time when all radio stations are in fear.
Those pricks are deleting as fast as shit gets posted.
Mm. Well, I got somebody on the case.
Actually, yeah, dancing was the big one, right?
All of us look a little silly dancing, don't we?
Well,
yeah, you do.
Hey, listen.
Is that for KFL, I mean?
I got the moves like Jagger, me and Bruffer.
I'm like nonstop erotic cabaret when I'm on the dance floor.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I am.
Sorry.
Like heads down, no nonsense, mindless boogie. That's the Bruffer.
You know what dance I love? The old man at the wedding reception dance.
Oh, that's a good one,
too. It's my favorite.
I like the crazy uncle with the lampshade dance.
Oh, my
that's
Uncle Bill.
Too. Yeah, Uncle Bill.
Anyways, that's not the right answer.
No, 1-877-945-BULL, 1-877.
Wow.
Oh, boy, is that their phone number?
Yeah.
Oh, no. That their phone?
Wait, I didn't hear that.
No.
I want to hear the last joke.
Hold on, I didn't hear
that. Yeah, let's hear the last joke.
I like the crazy uncle with the lampshade dance.
Oh, my Uncle Bill. Too.
Yeah, Uncle Bill.
Anyways, that's not the right answer.
No, 1-877-945-BULL, 1-877.
Oh, wow.
The lampshade dance, is that where you put your peter through the lampshade and you say, look at this, it's a snake light. Kiss the snake light.
Two photos posted on their Facebook. Yeah. One of Ric Flair having his tights pulled down by Hulk Hogan. Yes, these are men in their 60s and Ric Flair's ass is showing. And the other is a picture of the bullpen, except Mac's photo has been replaced by a giant black cock.
Ah.
Yes. These fucking people.
Yes.
Stellar.
I think this is more fun, man. Just see what the fucking listeners do with this shit.
Oh, my God.
Than actually doing Jocktober.
Yes, please. What happens next?
It just continues, I guess. And then finally the answer.
Wait.
What happened?
I believe we've entered. I incorrectly said phase three. I believe we've entered phase three.
What's phase three?
Lockout.
Which is they lock their wall so that only they can post on their wall.
Oh,
no. So what do we do now?
However, you can still comment on their posts.
Right.
For instance, their last post was from Friday, so they're deleting everything from today. And this post says, way to go, Jake from Zurich. Got the code and wins the key. First comment, I thought Jerry from Shepherdini won. It's all about Jerry Shepherdini.
So you can
right
comment
now
on their posts.
Yes.
All right, good. Yes. Stick with the first post because that's the one we're all watching right now.
Yeah.
So they continue to get an answer, and I guess
thank God
there's excitement or something.
Unscientific survey, more than a third of men made themselves look stupid while attempting to impress a woman doing this. What is this? Good morning, Bullpen. Who's this?
Good morning. It's Gwen calling.
Gwen, how are you?
I'm good.
Gwen, what do you think it is?
Well, I was just sitting there, and you had said it was close with the other guy. What about when he's trying to open the bottle of wine?
Congratulations.
Oh.
That's it? Yeah.
Good.
You've got it, Gwen. You've qualified for a shot at a key for the Bulls Ultimate Guys Garage 5.
Great.
Has somebody tried to impress you by opening wine and champagne?
Yes, with his asshole. He put the bottle in his asshole, and he told me to put my feet against his back and pull.
Hilarious. Why would you ask that question? If a guy's ever trying to impress you by opening up a bottle of wine. God.
That is so hilarious.
Stupid. The whole thing is dumb.
But you win a chance for the guy's ultimate garage.
Yeah.
Which is, it has a speaker with this show playing through it, and then towels you can put under the door, and a fucking exhaust pipe hose. That's the ultimate guy's garage.
It's like a takeoff on the man cave, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's the ball. Come on, the bullpen. They're giving away a man cave.
Has somebody tried to impress you by opening wine and champagne?
I can't say they have.
Yeah,
they should.
I think more. Yeah.
Well, Gwen, thank you. I'm going to put you on hold for a quick minute, but who feeds your need to rock?
94.5 the Bull.
Who feeds your need to rock? Oh, who
Sam
thought that one up?
Here's an angle for this Jocktober. You got to come up with all those fucking slogans.
Who feeds your need for rock? Well, who does it? If not 94.5 the Bull.
I'm going to guess 94.5 the Bull feeds my need for rock. My God, man. Yes.
I'm not going to read this one out loud.
Well, where is that from?
It's from their Facebook.
Someone wrote on their Facebook, Men's Health asked.
They asked the question, and then one of their listeners, I guess, answered it.
Men's Health asked his male readers, if your wife or girlfriend offered you one gift from the following list, what would you pick? And the answer is no nigs for a year would be great.
That's what one of their listeners commented
but
on
is that
Facebook.
But is that a... They're saying that's a list?
No. They added
they,
that
they decided they didn't like the list, and they had their own answer.
Oh. Yeah, they had their own suggestion.
Yes, yes.
Oh, my God.
So let's keep track of slogans this year.
Who feeds your need for rock?
Yeah. And let's vote best slogan ever this year. So keep track of that. That's
feeds your need. Who feeds your need to rock?
Who feeds your need to rock?
hey, has anybody ever impressed you by opening a wine bottle? Well, yes, I was on one date where he smashed the bottle against my forehead and they made me lick it off the ground like a dog while he kicked my spine.
Hey, where's Travis? We're going to go back to Jocktober. We got like a couple more clips to play, but Travis was at that Jack White show.
What a douche Jack White is.
And, yeah, Sam, you're a big fucking Jack White fan.
Douchebag.
You got his name tattooed on your arm.
Yeah.
He's a dick.
He was on Saturday.
Why?
What a dick.
I don't know.
Here's the story. I guess he played where? Radio City?
Yes.
And he played for maybe 45 minutes, and he was in a bad mood or something, walked off the stage, and there was almost a riot there. People were fucking pissed.
Yeah, he didn't like the sound.
And they were trying to... They were trying to, like, give back their merchandise and everything that they bought.
Instead of acknowledging from the stage, like, hey, look, the sound is off. I apologize. It's not our fault. It's this shitty venue.
Is that the excuse he's given?
That's a bullshit excuse.
Oh, okay.
Well, he has to come up with
something. The sound was fine.
To save face.
You can't say I was upset at some guy in the crowd, or I don't think the crowd was really into me, so I left.
So what happened, Travis? You were there.
Yeah, I mean...
Sold-out show, obviously.
Sold-out show, you know.
How close were you?
I was on the floor maybe about 30 rows back. You know, Radio City goes
pretty
far back.
Yeah, you had a nice seat, man.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they were decent seats. Show starts, everything's fine.
Who warmed up?
I don't know. We didn't go to the...
No one. Okay. The Tetley Five?
Yeah.
Fair enough. So everyone's excited. Jack White hits the stage.
Jack White hits the stage, plays a couple songs. Then he says something like, Jesus Christ, what is this, an NPR convention? You know, kind of commenting that the crowd's not as into it as he would like.
Yeah. What songs did he play before that?
He played a couple White Stripes songs, but like not
Dead
not
Leaves.
Popular. He played Dead Leaves later on. It was a retooled kind of like piano version, which is good.
That's all right. It's a while, but fuck,
yeah, you know,
just
he
the songs how I know.
He plays some White Stripes songs. Exactly. He plays some Dead Weather songs. He plays some Raconteurs songs. He plays some White Stripes songs. So I guess he wasn't really feeling the crowd. The crowd was okay. The crowd wasn't great, but they weren't
it happens.
Like.
Sure.
But was his performance lacking?
I've seen him before. It's not as good as I had seen him.
Mm-hmm. What's the problem?
I don't know. I mean, but you know, Sam saw him a couple months ago. He puts on a hell of a show.
Radio City is a weird venue for him. Because, like, he doesn't do shows where people can sit down in the front row.
But nobody's sitting. I mean, maybe people were sitting in the front row, but, like, nobody was sitting where I was. Like,
yeah,
everybody
but it's always
up.
Weird you when you have those chairs time. Around because you can't move.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I hate going to see any rock show at, like,
I get
Radio
that everyone's
City,
standing, but...
but
you're still confined to your seat area, and that's a little weird for a rock vibe, I think.
So, yeah, he made that, like, you know, I'm a little annoyed, like, you know, what is this, an NPR convention comment? And then, like, a couple songs later, like, afterward, right before he played Dead Leaves... he sat down at the piano. He's like, oh, quiet down, everyone, quiet down. Jeez, you're too loud, you know? So, you know.
He's a fucking baby.
There's another sarcastic comment.
Just maybe the crowd did stink, too. That happens. But you know what? You got to finish the gig.
You totally got
to. You don't do fucking 45 minutes. Do an hour and 20. Don't do 2 hours. Do an hour and 20. But you can't do 45 and walk off.
We interviewed him once. He's, I wouldn't say he's a dick. He was really strange. A strange guy.
He's a weird a rock star vibe. Guy. I know Sam loves him, but, you know.
No, I love his music, too.
So do I. That,
I really
that's
do.
Why we all have tats of him on our arm. You know, we all, it's
that's
obvious
right.
we adore the man. But
I was happy I wasn't at the show because he's amazing live, except, I guess, for that one night. And he was awesome when I met him. Like, he was nice and friendly and
cordial.
Happy. And
would you have been mad and just carved your fucking tat out of your arm like Maximus did in Gladiator? Apparently, you played a great set last night at Radio City.
So now, how did it go down?
So he plays Ball and Biscuit, which is White Stripes.
Nice, yeah.
Says something to the crowd. I couldn't understand what he was saying because it was very loud. And then he left, and everybody thought, all right, well, encore's coming in a couple minutes, you know. And
be long.
He should be forced to get that money back. People should demand that money back. If he did a way shorter show than the night before, they should clamor
for
the money.
He played 12 songs. He's averaging about 20 songs on the tour.
Yeah, so fucked the fans.
He barely played half.
Yeah, he's averaging about
12
2 hours.
12 songs, man. Those a lot of songs are short. That can't be more than 40 minutes.
It was a 55 minute show.
It was.
Yeah.
You really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking short.
Yeah, you know
do
who
an
plays,
extra half hour, you're done.
You know who plays 50-minute shows? Bands that just came out and have one
Katy
album.
Katy Perry?
Did I tell you how long Bruce Springsteen plays that shows?
Yeah, that's 12 fucking Jack White shows, Springsteen. That's
4 hours.
Yeah, exactly.
Jack White's got close to 10 albums to draw from. Yeah.
He does
Dead Weather songs, and he also does Raconteur songs.
I saw the your picture that you Instagrammed.
That was a great picture.
Which was, not quite as great as my good friend, Carly Folks, who was also
there. She was
there
as well, that's right.
And she had... the same view, only a fuck of a lot closer.
Yeah, she was like in like the fifth
row. She's my good friend, the T-Mobile girl.
Oh, the T-Mobile girl.
She's single?
Is on Instagram.
No, she's got a boyfriend. I'm waiting that one out.
That picture's after the show.
You guys talk a little bit here and there?
Oh, we've been known to, a little chit-chat, that's for sure.
So when he didn't come back, how did the crowd react? How did it build to the point where I heard rumors people were going to riot?
You kind of felt that like there was going to be a little, hipster riot there. About 5 minutes after, nothing was happening, the house lights came up and music started playing. And I've been to enough concerts where I know that's the show.
That's it.
Like, that's it. He's not coming back out. But they didn't draw the curtains down, so everybody just stayed. Everybody kept cheering. Everybody kept, trying to get him back out there. About 20 minutes after after he left the stage, they finally dropped that curtain.
Oh, shit.
They're probably asking him backstage, are you going to go on again?
That's what I'm thinking.
You know, someone was talking to him like, look, man, come on.
Nope. I don't like the crowd. Nope. Fucking cunty rock star.
Yeah, because
what a cunt.
If he was like, the sound sucks, we're not going to play anymore, then they would have said, show's over, guys, go home. They wouldn't have waited 20 minutes to drop that curtain. And then 10 minutes after they dropped that curtain, somebody finally had to come out on stage, either a security guy or one of his people, and say, the show's over, go home. All the doors, the doors on the side of Radio City open up directly onto the street.
Yeah.
Those doors open up, and it was just booze, fuck Jack White, fuck him. People going to the merch table and returning their merchandise.
Did they get their money back?
Yes.
They did?
Yeah, some people tweeted pictures of their refunded receipts.
Nice.
Of
course
they did. Did they get the money back for the show?
No, for their
fucking
merchandise.
Cunty rock star.
Radio 50 minutes at Radio City on a Saturday night.
That really fucking bugs me.
So what time did you leave?
Well, he came on at 9:12, and we probably left it.
Your Saturday night is done around 10:15.
Yeah, well, we left at like 10:45, I guess, because we stayed until.
Yeah, you were hanging open for something.
Yeah, because
I'm with Jimmy. What a dick!
What a twat!
Absolutely, yeah.
People work hard, and
it sucked.
Pay to see, and you pull.
Yeah, these
shit.
Weren't cheap tickets. These went from like $50 to like $150.
That's what's so annoying is the fact that people have to work really hard for that money. And if you have a bad show, you have a bad show. But don't bail out like a little faggot 45 minutes into
it. Suck it up.
I'm going to go home.
Gotta suck it up.
Fucking jizzbag. Give all that money back.
In retrospect, I'm really glad I was there because it was an experience.
It was a happening.
It was a happening. And now I told Danny in the back, I said, I didn't have an answer for what's the worst show you've ever been to. And now I definitely have one.
Whoa.
Wow.
Damn,
and it's got to be fucking Sam's Hero.
Yeah.
I like Jack White, too.
I hate fucking rock stars that don't treat their, or anyone that doesn't treat their fans.
It was a very
like
Axl Rose.
Another jerk off move.
My worst show, Neil Young, when he didn't play.
Oh, yeah,
any
you
hits.
Didn't like that.
Oh, my God. That annoyed me just listening to you tell the story. I was fucking fuming.
I laughed so hard. The guy.
See Neil Young. He fucking pulls that shit.
But I was so entertained by the guy behind me that just his excitement slowly went away when he realized the chances of hearing a hit were fading quickly. And he started going, this is bullshit. And then he was the guy, if you know the story, that finally stood up and said, hey, Neil, how about one for us?
How about one for us?
I'll never forget
that. What a great line, though, to throw out there.
This guy was going to rip his seat out. He was so mad. But he was the guy, he was the uber Neil Young fan that was sitting right behind me.
Oh,
he
just
all
wanted
in.
To hear Cinnamon Girl and fucking...
Right.
And he gets these obscure, brand new fucking...
I forgot what it was.
Noodling
now.
For his own pleasure shit up on stage. But hate when they do that.
But my dumb point, we didn't know going into it that was the show. Yeah. I mean, if you're a fan of a band and they go, look, okay, we're going to do something different. Let's say it's Springsteen. We're going to play all B tracks. Are you cool with that? If you are.
Yeah, totally. I know I'm on anyway. But
tell us ahead of time so you go, you know what? Yeah, I would go see all B tracks, B sides, whatever. You know? Yeah. But when you're fucking blindsided like that.
Yeah, and then you said the guy was so mad.
Hey, Neil, how about one for us?
No shit.
I heard he pulled the same thing in Central Park this weekend. There was a
big rock show.
Of course
he did. Are you kidding me?
I don't know.
I could have gone to that. That was Saturday night. I had tickets for that.
A couple people tweeted me and said,
ticket maven.
Well, they were free.
A couple people tweeted me. They said they were above average Neil Young fans, meaning they know, you know, a wide variety of songs by him. And he supposedly only played about two that most people would know.
I heard the Foo Fighters were very good.
You have tickets for them?
No, at Central Park. They played at Central Park.
That annoys me so,
I was so upset.
Fucking much.
I've never seen anything like it. Like I was standing there, and these two girls behind us, they're like, "Do you think he's coming back out?" I'm like, "There's no possible way."
And they said,
"He's
going to
wait,
creepy guy."
Yeah, exactly. We don't like your beard. You're weird.
Like, there's no possible way he's going to wait 45 minutes and then come back out after nearly, you know, the entire crowd turning against him.
What do you know, Dr. Gay?
That's what they said.
My second worst concert, I'm being reminded because Brian on Long Island had the same experience. And I like the guy, but Bob Dylan fucking blows in concert. No. Doesn't acknowledge the crowd, looks down the entire fucking time. People are cheering. He doesn't even acknowledge that you're fucking cheering for him. And then he changes the arrangement of every fucking song to the point you don't know what the song is anymore. And then, of course,
he's an artist.
You don't understand his lyrics because he mumbles. It was horrendous.
Lauren
and I know that's
going to
piss off a lot of Bob Dylan people today, but... I hate it.
He's just like Neil. He's
I
like
hated
Neil
the Bob Dylan show. That was in Rochester. Like, fuck, that could be 20 years ago at this point. Brian, go ahead.
Yeah, my friend got tickets. I really don't care for Bob Dylan too much, but he is Bob Dylan. And it was at Jones Beach, which is an awesome theater. Perfect night. And we go there, and I'm like, what do I expect? He's Bob Dylan. He did not play one song that anybody knows. He plays, like, I don't know if it's new hits or just, like, songs, and then I didn't even understand what he was talking about because you can't understand his lyrics.
I remember
about some. How does it feel?
How about some of that?
Well, I remember 10 minutes into Like a Rolling Stone, I went, "Oh, this is like Rolling Stone."
Now it's Rolling Stone.
What the fuck? He stinks.
Eight songs, we're saying, if the next one, we don't know, we're leaving. And we did that like 9 times. And yeah. He was doing the same special, and then we were just like, we're out of here, this fucking bloat.
And then how about the one no one even knows it's him? Lee, lee, lee,
lee across my big brass beard.
It's like, wait, that's Dylan?
For the longest, thank you, sir. For the longest time, I was with you. I had no idea
that
was
a Dylan
fan.
Stay with
your
man a while.
Dylan song.
Do you think more people in me and Sam's generation know Bob Dylan for Bob Dylan or for Soy Bomb?
Soy Bomb.
Good old Soy Bomb.
Soy Bomb's a man.
Yeah. Soy Bomb. Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, it did suck. Yeah, it's disappointing because I know how good he is live.
Supposedly the Foo Fighters broke up too, right?
Well,
they were playing the Central Park concert as well.
Yeah, and he said, he said something to the effect of, "This is the last time we're going to play together for a while." So whatever that means, it sounds very non-committal.
Yeah, but
I think they're taking a very extended break.
He must be a prick to work with.
Dave Grohl?
Oh, I thought you meant fucking Jack White.
Mm. Yeah,
but he must be a prick to work with, Jack White.
Yeah,
that's what I'm thinking. Yeah. But Dave Grohl? No, Dave Grohl seems like
Dave Grohl seems awesome. Yeah.
When we used to,
I'm sorry, you were talking. I wasn't paying attention.
That's that's not nice. I'm right here.
Oh,
what? Next to you.
Oh, hey, Travis. Hi.
Jack White is a perfectionist, but
he's a twat. He's probably a brilliant musician, but enough of the genius moniker. He's a cunt. If you walk off after 50 minutes and fuck your fans like that, you're a cunt, and you got no respect for the fact they spent that kind of money to come see you.
None.
That drives me nuts. If he had a bad show, believe me, I've seen Ozzy when he was not at his best, but he never walked off like a fucking cocksucker.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen his voice shot. Finish the fucking show.
Yeah.
Finish the fucking show, baby.
I saw Courtney Love about 10 years ago, and her... Yeah, I know.
Sorry.
And she lost her voice in the second song, and she played for an hour and a half.
I bet Ozzy tried, and Sharon just, like, kicked him back onto the stage.
Yeah.
From side stage, she's got to chase him. No!
Yeah, you saw a shoe on his ass the entire time.
Just pushing him back
out. But any band you want to mention, like, just to... as a performer, you think I've never had a fucking crowd, and I was like, ugh. I didn't love Cincinnati last time I went. I wanted to walk off the 8 minutes one of the... Can't do it.
Gotta go.
Fucking use all the years you've been performing. Put together a decent set. whether it's the crowd or it's you, sometimes you walk off and you go, the only thing that salvaged that was the fact that I've been doing this for 20 years.
Wow.
And I know how to fucking, it's like you know how to do smoke and mirrors and put together a good show.
Right. Yeah.
Like you know how to make it. People go, all right, that was cool. But to walk off after fucking, it makes me crazy.
I was telling Travis, it was also very bad timing. Because the same morning that this news breaks of, you know, the fans almost rioting because Jack White walked off, Justin Bieber was in concert that same night. And Justin Bieber threw up on the stage because he had, like, a flu or something.
Oh, yeah, sure, the flu.
And he kept performing. And it's like if Justin Bieber is now out rock starring you.
Oh, God.
How's that video, by the way?
I saw that clip. I don't understand why the Biebs didn't just walk back in where he came out on stage. Like he bends over... Like that. Why doesn't he just walk? Look how long it's taken him to puke.
Wow. I wonder if fans were scrambling to eat it up.
Wow.
You know one would have easily.
Yeah, because he wanted everyone to notice that he was puking.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's one of those.
Oh, no.
Puking's a weird thing, dude. Yeah. That's a fucking horrible. I respect him more, though, for continuing to play.
Yeah,
that's a hysterical shot of him just bent over like that.
Puking.
Yeah.
All right, good for the Biebs.
Better than Jack White.
So here's the
Here's
the Foo Fighters announcement.
Mm-hmm.
They've been out a long time. You think they're going to take a year or two off?
Yeah.
I guess. I mean, they could. Why not?
Without making a big deal out of it, we don't have any shows after this. This is it, man. We don't have any ones after this. This is the show where we come out. And we play as many songs as we can in a short period of time. Because honestly, I don't know when we're going to do it again. And this is the perfect place to do it right now, tonight. You know what I mean?
What's that about?
That was very vague.
He just wants to take some time off.
But that's a little dramatic.
At the end of the show.
Want people to think they might be breaking up?
That was in the E-Rock category of vagueness.
Did you see the show?
Yeah, what? Did you see the show?
Hey.
At the end of the show, he said, like, I don't know when, but we'll see you soon.
Mm.
They'll
be back.
Because they're up in that category now of, like, you know, one of the biggest rock bands. And they're starting to do that whole play 3.5 hours long sets.
You mean they don't walk off after 50 minutes?
No. Their sets are longer than Dexter's premiere last night.
Well, what was that?
What? An hour.
Oh, you scared me. Like, Dexter was, like, 14 minutes.
How was it?
It's great. It was really good.
People love.
You should really watch that show.
No, I should. I hope he only killed bad guys.
You have to get past it.
No, I can't get past it.
Travis goes, you have to get past it.
I can't. I mean, I'm sure he's a great actor. It's not about the acting.
But you got to think that's going to be a twist eventually. We're like, oh, fuck. I thought this guy only killed bad guys.
It's a great
show. I don't like when a show is so set up for me because the fucking people who designed it went to likability 101 school. We have to make the character likable. Drives me fucking crazy.
I hate when they go for the dramatic death and then, you know, next season they figure out a way out of it. I hate that shit. The cancer show with the fucking father there dropping dead as the cancer woman is running the fucking marathon.
Huh?
The big C.
And then it turns out, oh no, he just had a heart attack and he's recovering at home now.
Spoiler.
He's okay. This is a couple years ago.
Spoiler alert.
But it was so dramatic because you're focused on the woman with the cancer is going to die, and then it turns out, no, he dies.
It's lazy writing.
And that's how they handled it at the end of that season. He's dead. But then they're like, well, all right, we'll just sit on it and then make, you know, we'll have him come back. It was just a heart attack.
Yeah.
So fucking commit, man. Go all in. Can we play Dead Leaves?
Hmm? That's a great song.
Yeah.
I love
it. It is a great
Leaves.
Song.
There's so many great songs.
Oh, what's our slogan today? I can't even remember.
Oh, wait, we feed your need for rock.
Yeah. Feeds your need for rock?
We're going to feed
Who feeds E-Rock? What?
We're going to feed your need for rock right now with a little White Stripes, Dead Leaves. It's a short song. And then Jocktober when we return. We'll be right back.
can hear me coming down the hall. If I could just hear your pretty voice, I don't think I need to see at all. Don't think I need to see at all. Soft hair and a velvet tongue, I wanna give you what you give to me. And every breath that is in your lungs is a tiny little gift to me. Is a tiny little gift to me. Tell you what he loves the most.
We're going to wrap up Jocktober for today.
Yeah!
We're featuring a show out of Canada.
Oh, terrible.
The Bullpen with Bruffer, Mac, and K-Fell on 94.5 The Bull.
It is, so far, has been horrible with all the features. The whole, the old radio veteran. Yeah. And the wild guy is kind of, he's out there, yells a lot.
I don't find it to be bad. I find it to, it's like, because it's about time there's a mix of things. You know what I mean? You have to realize that there's a lot of people out there, and you can have a little bit of craziness with a guy like K-Fell. Some just solid humor with a guy like Bruffer.
Right.
And then Mac is there to make sure that everybody kind of just stays together.
Doesn't get too crazy.
Yeah, because you don't want that.
So it's a perfect balance, huh?
Yeah, because fun is
fun. I don't like
fun.
A show that gets crazy like that. I like that she's there to keep that from happening.
It's something most broadcasters don't realize, is fun is fun, but only to an extent.
Right.
Well, you don't want it to go too far, because then half the audience... I like a lady's point of view.
Oh, yeah.
Because a lot of times the ladies will bring it back down. We get carried away.
Right. Now, like, I didn't think about it from that perspective type of thing.
Guys.
And that's why this is a valuable show to listen to.
Right.
Like, I enjoy it more than this one, personally.
Yeah, I think it's good-natured, and it just, you know, people can listen to it with the kids around.
Thank God
Mac is there to come on now.
You can put it on in the stores.
Sure. Yeah.
That's why I brought this to the table. I feel like you guys get a little nasty sometimes, and maybe listening...
Blue. We work blue sometimes.
Listening to the Bullpen would make you think, oh, maybe I should adjust my broadcasting
style.
That's
the talent, to be able to do it within the guidelines.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. That's a problem with satellite radio. Not enough restrictions.
On a side note, is Jennifer Hutt pissed?
Oh, boy.
Are you going to have the exclusive interview at 10 o'clock?
She said she'd come on the after show,
What is she doing now?
She's here stalking Chelsea Handler because she's doing Howard's show. So I guess she's going to, I don't know.
Get a pick or something?
I don't know.
You can't get her anymore. We tried. Roland goes, I tried.
I try.
I wonder, too, if the Howard's people are being more territorial because he's only on a few days.
Of course they are.
Like almost.
Of course.
Because there's not as many live shows.
Right.
So to keep that show feeling special, like when we get somebody, we keep them exclusive to us because what else differentiates it?
Yeah that could be.
I mean, that's my. This is a guess.
Have fun playing that stupid game. It's 2012.
Yeah, I don't like
the
it.
Guest thing. It's enough.
I know.
Anyway, let's get back to Jocktober. The Bullpen with Bruffer, Mac, and K-Fell on 94.5. The Bull. It's the Bullpen's casting couch. Really? What's this about, Sam?
Oh, that sounds risque.
Yeah, it is a little risque. What they do is they go on Prepburger, and they find wacky news stories.
Wait, the whole show is Prepburger. My God, man.
Except these wacky news stories refer to celebrities. So it's a celebrity wacky news stories from Prepburger.
You sure it's on Prepburger?
Yep.
Did I say that?
No, they don't announce that. But the fact that, you know, if you listen to any number of shows on a given day and they're covering these same stories, it's because they're Prepburger. You can tell, especially, I mean, let's be honest.
Why do they call it Prepburger?
That I don't know.
Because you prepare a burger?
A burger.
And the morning show itself is the burger?
Yeah, you're serving it up to the people every morning.
This is the fifth year of
Jocktober. And every burger is different, but it's how you prepare it.
God, why? Maybe that's it.
I'm trying to figure out why they would call their service the prep burger.
Some are well done. Others are a bit rare.
Can we see the prep burger? Can we bring it up?
I can't because I don't have a username and all that stuff.
Why? We have nobody that belongs to Prepburger?
We did last year or something.
I've talked about it.
Not for our show, by the way, assholes.
How much is it to join?
Don't spin that shit.
Yeah, right?
I don't know. Well, I'm going to see if I can get a membership this year.
Let's join it by tomorrow because we could mock it and go on and hear other radio shows. I would love to get a bunch of radio shows doing the same story.
We could mock Prepburger. After Jocktober's long gone.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. The Bullpen's casting couch.
Right now at the Bull.
Because nobody's a true star until they've been on the Bullpen's casting couch. Here's what the who's who idiots in Hollywood are up to today.
I don't know if this is good news or bad news, but it might be ugly. Not one, but two sex tapes are out there for Kanye to worry about right now. According to TMZ, they say that the tape we heard about yesterday featuring Kanye getting it on with Kim Kardashian, or a Kim Kardashian lookalike, isn't the only one being shopped around. The second tape is said to be twice as long, lasting 40 minutes, and apparently that's nonstop action.
I have a question for celebrities out there. Why do you insist on taping it when you're doing it?
Because they're used to being on camera.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that's a good one. Because he's a tool.
Why are you trying to hammer? Real answer there?
Right, yeah, she comes back with the facts.
That's not why they do it.
Yeah, because they want to jerk off to it later. Silly.
Come on,
Jim. For celebrities out there, why do you insist on taping it when you're doing it?
Because they're used to, you know, being on camera.
Have you ever starred in a sex tape, KFL?
No.
No, me either. No, I'd be way too embarrassed for that.
No girl wants to show anyone that they were with me.
Aw, oh, come on. You're much too hard on yourself.
Stop it.
Hard on.
Was that a hard on joke?
That's a hard on joke. You can hear him go, but he knew. He knew better than to delve into that.
But even more importantly, did you hear Mac's response to the joke?
Uh-oh.
Because we were so busy processing. Go to the end of the clip.
Hard on.
All right.
Because if you're spending time processing.
Anyone that they were with me.
Aw, oh, come on. You're much too hard on yourself.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Oh, God.
Stop it.
That's why I'm here. It's time to stop this right now.
Was she really offended by that? Was she out to be like, stop it? Or does she just take miles a dick and has to make believe that she's offended?
It's just a world out there we don't understand. That's how people fucking live their lives.
Oh, God. Well, you know, hard-ons can refer to erections.
Whoa.
Is that what the deal is? I didn't know. Right. So she's kind of whoa, before this goes nuts.
Rumor has it the Facebook page is not happening right now. There's a rumor. A little rumor going on.
And the Facebook page is down. It's gone. the Facebook page.
No.
What do you mean it's down?
Why would they do that?
94.5 The Bull.
Yeah.
The Bullpen.
Yeah.
Does not have a Facebook page.
Oh, we've reached that level.
You go to this link right here. It's the Bullpen on Facebook. Yeah. Right? That's something I just clicked on a couple minutes
click
ago.
Click that right there.
Just click that, and it goes right to the Facebook homepage.
Oh.
Which means...
So sorry.
Oh. It's gone.
Sorry. Is there a Twitter? I want to just see if they're updating their Twitter.
Yeah.
They started their day like any other day.
What's their Twitter?
And a mere couple hours later, they're deleting their page.
They have to fucking take their Facebook page offline.
I just want to read their tweets and see if they're Twittering.
I don't know what their Twitter is.
Yeah.
Does anybody know?
I don't know.
They
should have tweeters.
You think so.
What's the morning mooch?
Oh, the morning mooch. Oh.
We're almost done with today's Jocktober.
The morning mooch is where kickoff, too. Where you can, the listeners are mooching off the show hosts, meaning... They call in and get a prize.
What?
Yep. It's another call in for a prize thing. But this time, the morning mooch involves the theater of the mind less.
Whoa.
And what happens there is two members of the show will read a movie scene, like act it out together, and then they'll give lots of very obvious clues, hoping that maybe one person might call.
Oh, wait, is this true?
What's
there? There's an at 95 the bull. That would be 95 the bull Twitter.
I don't know if that's the same stage because it's 94.5.
See? What are you doing? Yeah. Oh, well, then there's an at KFEL945.
That sounds like him.
That's KFEL.
At K.
He's the one that sounds like Chris Griffin.
KFEL945.
That's KFEL. All
how many
right.
followers does he have?
Oh, look
how
at
many
this.
Follow- oh, man.
He's dressed up for Halloween.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Zach Galifianakis from The Hangover.
Oh.
That's a little nuts.
Oh, God. What is this?
Jimmy, look.
Oh, no.
You felt so good about the picture. It's his avatar.
Holy shit.
Did you see the movie?
God. Maybe.
He got crazy.
Yeah, he did get crazy. He had, like, the baby attached to the
baby. He's got the beer. How many followers?
Oh, wow. He's got a 170 followers.
Thousand? What?
170
you know,
thousand
followers.
You know that half,
oh.
You know that half our listeners have more followers than that guy that's doing radio?
Oh, I like his background, though.
This son of a bitch asshole.
Yeah?
His tweet. He just writes, WWE is so bad.
Oh, well, there's a problem
if
now.
If that doesn't warrant an attack, I don't know what does.
Maybe he means good.
Maybe bad like good, like Michael Jackson bad.
94.5 The Bull is a pretty good Twitter account. They have 144 followers.
Oh, wow.
Come on.
What are you doing as a radio station?
Oh, my God,
when
right?
you can promote it around the clock.
What are you Twittering? Nothing but vomit photos?
Those would get more.
I'm sure. Yeah. And they're smart, too. Like, they're really on top of everything. Their last tweet was on the 25th of July. So they're really making sure everything stays updated.
Really using
fresh.
That new medium.
Wow. Radio.
Yeah.
It just stinks, radio.
Let's get into the morning mooch.
Oh. Yeah.
The morning mooch.
What do you want for
sounder for everything.
In association with Pete's Auto Body, just south of Owen Sound.
Okay, sponsor. We're going to play Theater of the Mindless here this morning. 1-877-945-BULL, 1-877-945-2855, or pound the cell at 2855, toll free.
Whoa, you can pound the cell.
Pound the cell?
Pound the cell, baby.
The last T-cell.
But
more importantly, are they going to feed my need for rock and roll?
Only if you pound the cell at the right time.
All right.
Someone writes, by the way, oh, Jimmy, I live in the area of the bull, and they have changed their voices and are pissed at yous. Love it.
Pissed Whoa. At yous. Whoa. Oh, nice.
Are they mad at us for what?
I don't know. I mean, why would they?
Have some laughs.
Sam, isn't this in good fun?
This is all in good
it's
fun.
It's all in good fun.
It's just like if it's a good, if we enjoy it, we'll comment on that. If there are some things that we have a difference of opinion on.
Holla.
2855 toll free. Got a pair of tickets to the Woodstock Wood Show, which is coming up at the end of September. So we need a herd member right now. So you guys want to perform this?
Yeah, let's do it.
Absolutely. Okay, this is featuring Mac and K-Phil. This
All
morning.
Right.
So anytime you're ready, guys.
All right, here we go. Every ex-player turned coach says that they prefer coaching over playing. Why would they all say that?
Because they can't play.
So I think maybe it has something to do with hockey.
It does.
What do you think? 1-877-945-BULL. 1-877-945.
What is that? What are they doing?
What happened? What's going on?
What's the game?
It's too highbrow for us. We don't even understand it.
Well,
no. The problem is that you guys might think there's no way it could possibly, but it is. You just now.
Is it Slapshot?
They read two lines from a movie.
What happened?
And then the listeners call up. And name the movie.
Oh, what is the line again? I didn't realize it's two lines from a movie.
That's right.
There's not many hockey movies, though. Is it Slapshot?
Well, and then this is the part where they start giving away very obvious clues. Okay.
Yeah. Why would they all say that?
Because they can't play.
So, I think maybe it has something to do with hockey.
Dice.
What do you think? 1-877.
Why would he give away that card? I'm so mad right now.
Dice.
It was vague enough. Let me walk people through this. It was vague enough where it's like, okay, you got to think sports movies. But then he goes, oh, it has something to do with hockey. There was nothing in there that says that it's actually hockey.
No.
And there's literally like one hockey movie.
I thought it was The Accused.
Love that. Slapshot or The Mighty Ducks, I think. That's about it.
And then instead of keeping the mystery alive, it's saying, I don't know, KFL goes, it does.
Who hears it does again?
Yeah.
They can't play.
So, I think maybe it has something to do with hockey.
Could have been
dice.
What do you think? 1-877-945-BULL, 1-877-945-2855, or pound the cell at 2855, toll free.
Do that again, guys.
All right.
All right. Every ex-player turned coach says they prefer coaching over playing. Why would they all say that?
Because they can't play.
That's not a... It's
I think there's
obvious.
A reference to a...
That's not obviously hockey.
No. No, not of course at all. Not.
Why don't you just take the seventh caller?
Because they realize that nobody would ever call in for that, because nobody would
true.
Possibly know.
What, with 144 fucking Twitter followers?
It's very... There's such few listeners that, you know, out of that pool... To know what that line is from is impossible.
Does. It does. He was so excited.
It's terrible.
They all know the answer.
It's the worst does ever.
Does.
Does.
I think there's a reference to a walrus in this movie.
Oh, I know. I know the movie. Sorry in advance. It's the Eric Nagel story.
He's not quite as big as a walrus. Course.
My apologies.
Hey, Eric, how was your weekend? I forgot to ask him about his weekend. Oh, I love Mondays. Great. Yeah, what'd you do? How did you consume this Monday? This
fan
weekend?
Fiction. Legos.
Yeah.
Right.
What was it?
No, DVDs. No Legos. No oh. fan fiction.
Whoa.
How'd you consume as a good American?
Let's see. I watched the new animated Batman movie.
Ugh. Why?
Oh, why would you do that? What do you mean the new
fucking
animated Batman movie?
I could just sit through
What
that.
Is that? Does anyone even know?
No. Everybody's an adult.
Oh, you like cartoons?
There's another Batman movie besides the one everyone else
well,
saw?
Well, DC puts out animated ones, too.
Oh, God.
Do they?
Was it good?
Yeah, it was very good.
It was
what was it
very
called?
Very good.
It's a take on the Dark Knight series. It's very violent.
Called what?
It's a cartoon. Stop violent.
The Dark Knight Returns?
Yeah.
Oh, so it's based on the comic?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stinks.
Did you,
it was awesome.
I bet the animation stunk.
That's it?
Watch Doctor Who.
Oh, my
It's just
God.
Childish movies all weekend.
Who's not a childish movie?
Would you play with your Elmo doll? What, no. Name your Cabbage Patch?
Worked on the
Cunt.
House a little bit.
What do you do around the house?
Set.
Color forms on the fridge. Baby.
Huh?
Wiring a network downstairs.
Ooh.
Al-Qaeda.
Ooh. Any yard work?
Nah, it was raining most of the time.
Was it raining this weekend? Not where I was.
Yeah, a little bit.
Maybe a little.
It poured yesterday.
It was a shower yesterday. Yeah. It lasted for about 10 minutes, I think.
Friday it rained. Yeah, I guess you're right. All right, let's get back to this, the morning mooch thing.
Who's the captain of the team?
BB.
Oh, man. I just saw this again the other night. I can't believe. Come on, Herd, you're hockey fans, for crying out loud. Not saying this is the best hockey film ever. It's no Slapshot, for sure.
No, it's no Mighty for Ducks sure. 1.
Oh, so
no, it's not even Mighty Ducks 1.
Come on, Herb. I'm trying to get the crowd in.
I'm so out. That's the only two hockey movies I know.
So they've said it's a
Although
hockey
Goon
movie.
Was great.
It's a hockey movie that's not Mighty Ducks and it's not Slapshot.
By the way, we didn't pick up on it, but Doug certainly did. You know what? Let's give Doug a little fucking spotlight right now. Doug, go ahead.
Yeah, but before they started this clip, they refer to their audience as the Herd.
I know.
The Herd?
Because the station's called The Bull.
They're the bullpen.
Exactly. And they're the bullpen.
And the listeners are the Herd.
Yeah.
And what they put out is fucking is bullshit.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
They refer to their audience as the Herd.
It's not just them. It's the audience referring to themselves. I'm a proud Herd member myself.
Yeah. Well, good for you.
I tell you, I was walking this and my hooves are just killing me today. Everything's a dumb hoof, bull reference. Yeah. Hey, ho, ho.
Gonna wrangle the listeners in.
I'm a little horny. Whoa, look out.
Oh, come on.
Oh, I'm sorry.
One way or another.
Good one, good one.
Yuck.
Well, you want to get the answer?
Yes.
Please.
All right, then.
Hey, the bull, who's this?
It's Valerie.
Valerie, what do you think?
Is that not the Mystery Alaska?
Yay!
And whoa. Russell Crowe is the captain?
Yes.
Woo!
Yes,
he is.
Good. All over this.
It was our awesome acting, I'm sure.
It was.
Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you. I will be doing that line later on.
A couple of tickets to the Woodstock Wood Show. Congratulations to you.
Okay.
Perfect. Who feeds you need to rock?
945.
Why?
What's wrong with their phones?
There's nothing wrong with their phones. There's something wrong with the pre-recording they did of that phone call. The audio is obviously fucked up. But they realize that they're not going to get another caller any way in hell.
Mm-hmm.
So they're like, well, we just got to play it.
Why do you have to say who feeds your need for rock? And she answers, you guys
the PD fucking hammers that in your head. You get the slug line out there. Look, make sure.
We've done slug lines in the past.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
They're terrible.
Not perfect.
Feed your need for rock.
We did work at the only station that really rocks, so.
Yeah, but they didn't feed any. You didn't feed anybody's need for rock.
Oh. No, we don't even feed people's need for laughter or entertainment.
I think we might have asked the question, what's the only station that really rocks, though?
Uh-huh.
And there we go.
Yeah.
AAF.
Yeah.
But AAF doesn't feed my need.
In Iran, like the they feed does. Your need for rocks.
Yeah.
When you're homo.
And if you're looking for a good hockey movie, The Goon is a great one.
Oh, there you go.
With Sean William Scott, who came in and promoted that movie.
Uh-oh. Norm says, get ready. They played Get Back and told the Herd to nail yous.
No.
I what? Bet they played Get Back by the Beatles.
Oh, really? Let's sit here and wait for a phone call from their audience.
Okay.
Well, they're having a little fun back there, Jimmy.
I like that.
It's
I good like
natured.
Everybody, check your Twitters for attacks.
Mm-hmm.
And we might have to take down some Facebook pages. E-Rock, you ready? Be on the ONA Facebook page because
standing
you might
by.
Have to.
Standing by, E-Rock. So there you go. Who are we going to feature tomorrow? That's it for today.
Well, I'm not going to tell you who we're going to feature tomorrow. We will have a nice show, but.
That means you don't know. You don't know yet.
There's no advance notice given to these shows.
Mm.
I'm prepared. But there's no advance notice. Everybody's been doing a good job of tweeting suggestions, though. Just tweet them, not Sam. And then I'll favorite the tweet, and then I'll have everything.
Oh, stop trying to get more Twitter followers.
That's not my ambition.
All right. Fox News airs Suicide Live.
Yeah. You got any of those calls from the bullpen? Or
they were waiting. I don't see it.
That was one of their listeners on Fox. Oh, the show stopped.
Kingston Pete, he's a regular on the Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
He writes, the Bull is in Wingham, Ontario, if that makes sense to people.
Yep.
Population, 2,923 people.
What?
I live 4 hours from this town and just learned it existed today. Wow, you went deep for fucking Jocktober.
This was a listener suggestion.
You went deep.
I thought it was important to highlight the bullpen.
That's a tiny little radio station.
Yeah,
it's market number 500 in Ontario.
That's the beauty of Jocktober. No matter how far tucked away you are.
Oh, you're never safe.
You will be attacked.
Yes, you're
no
never
reason.
Safe.
You don't think shows enjoy when they're featured?
I think it could possibly be the worst thing. For some of them, the worst thing in their careers. Because they're just not used to being made fun of.
No.
At all. Like, they're used to being this little show that, you know, half a dozen people listen to and like, and the rest of everybody else just leaves them alone.
Six people are listening.
Yeah.
But he says it like it's absolutely a fact. Yeah. I checked into it. No, it's six people.
Half a dozen.
Yeah, like, asshole.
Half a
so
dozen.
They're not used to like severe criticism.
Right.
You're gonna be snorting.
And so when there's like, you know, hundreds to thousands of people just attacking them for no reason. They did nothing.
Yeah.
They don't know how to cope.
You think they'll spin it in a good way? Like, hey, any kind of publicity.
Yeah.
This is good for us.
I hope we end up in Canadian newspapers.
Oh,
that'd be nice.
A little press.
In honor of Jocktober, I could put some focus on me.
What happened with you?
Someone tweeted me something over the weekend, and I was by myself when I pushed play, and I was completely embarrassed for myself.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Wow.
Completely embarrassed.
Oh, do tell.
Well.
You know, we all have our crutches here on the Opie and Anthony show.
Uh-huh.
And I'm aware of some of mine, but I swear to you, a bunch of people obviously picked up on a crutch I do. And when I heard this, I went, oh my God, I had no idea I did this.
Oh, no.
Is there a montage?
It was beyond douche chilling, yeah. Yeah, let me see.
Oh.
Do you know of any of your crutches? We all have them.
I know mine, yeah.
What's yours?
I know
do you want to just write it down so they don't do a montage of it?
No, I don't care. I think it's kind of funny. But
I had no idea about this one. I know I use this one word. I do know I use it, but I didn't realize to the extent.
I do this even off the air. I do this one. It's if somebody says something really funny, I just repeat it. not trying to do the joke again, but if, like, you know, you just fucking say something, and it's like, and then the door fell off, I'll be like, the door fell off.
Yeah.
I do that all the time. I know I do. Ha ha, noises.
My crutch, and I know it, and I hate it, is that I bring constant entertainment value.
Entertainment value.
Who gets the credit today? This got to go on the Facebook page. It's Ryan, what's his name there? He might even be a hater, but I don't care.
Ryan Walling.
It got me. I was just douche chilling bad. Just play it. I had no idea. I swear to you, I had no idea I did it to this extent.
Was he howling?
Yeah.
Laughing my ass off.
I was howling.
Oh.
And I started howling out loud. I couldn't help it. And
there's a montage of wolves going on.
Everyone was howling on Twitter that in the end, they picked a dog act to win America's Got Talent.
I was howling.
E-Rock, were you howling? Like, I always used to howl when your friend would come to, like, a party or like, someone in your family brings that girl with massive tits. We put the mustache on her.
Oh, she
made us howl
exactly.
For weeks.
I hope you guys continue this, because we're howling over here today. How great is that? That is making us howl this morning.
My chip is hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
I was howling. Dude, we've been fucking howling.
Then I brought my brothers. We were howling.
There's another thing that happened on this date, which is makes me howl, man.
You know, I couldn't get back to everyone yesterday, but a lot of people had me howling with their tweets about the hula hoop girl.
Yeah.
Howling.
The move that bus had me howling.
Well, the one with the black mom starts, she just passes out.
Oh, yeah. We howled at that one. We thought that was
I don't know that one.
Oh, my God.
Is this all from one day?
Oh, my God.
It was
God.
The last few days, but now that, that is posted, I know I say it a lot, but I had no idea.
Well, we know who your favorite character on Gilligan's Island is.
Did you guys know?
No, I never noticed.
Did you know that
never.
Crutch?
No.
Never.
Never even noticed?
Now that they brought it up, I know I absolutely say that a lot.
That was really funny because during the video, all they're playing is wolves, like howling.
I never noticed it.
And then I tweet and I write the word howl a lot, too, because they put that up there as well. I had no idea. I saw this over the weekend. I was embarrassed and there was no one around.
Oh, no.
put that on the Facebook page there, E-Rock.
Will do.
All right. See?
My crutch is that I say anti-disestablishmentarianism too much. Gee, there's a Halloween store in our neighborhood.
Yeah, that joint just stays there with nothing in it for a year.
And then it opens up.
Once a year, they got to make all their money.
Well, yeah, because no one else is renting the space.
Yeah.
So the Halloween people rent it every year.
I'm opening a Halloween store!
Oh, Ted.
Ted?
I bet you it's some kind of emporium.
Yes, it is, Gregory! It's Ted's Spooky Ookie Goblins and Ghouls Halloween Emporium.
Spooky Ookie?
Yes, it is, Anthony.
Is that it?
I opened it on October 31st at 8:30 p.m.
Well, that's kind of
not smart.
A little late. People wait to get their Halloween needs.
How many costumes do you sell?
I have about 40,000 for sale.
And how many have you actually sold?
Six. Well, they were actually stolen off the truck.
Don't you think it's a little late? Like, people already have their costumes?
No, at 8:30 on Halloween night, they're going to start rolling in to purchase their goodies.
You should open it up now, Ted.
No, I don't want to. Rent is too high, Gregory. I open it that night, and I keep it open until December 4th.
Why would you do that?
This way, it's on Halloween, and people can go, let's go get our goodies. No, let's do it at 8:30 p.m.
That's when they're out there already trick-or-treating.
No, I have bushels of candy to sell, too.
Yeah, what kind of candy do you sell?
I sell only Malamars.
That's a cookie, isn't it? Throw it in the bag. So melty. Oh, well, what kind of costumes are we looking at over there? What's your best sellers?
Oh, I have the Superman. I have a cape, actually. Like you say, you can be Superman with this cape. And I have a wig.
That's a cape and a wig?
20,000 of each.
That would be the worst store ever.
No, it's wonderful. You could be the caped wigged crusader.
Is it a different color wigs or is it
just... No, it's just black and a red cape and Malamars.
I don't think this business is going to do very well.
Can't people go get free candy at 8:30 p.m. on Halloween night?
No, but you should buy it and then go home and give it out to all the children. It'll make you feel wonderful, Samuel.
By the time you get home...
It'll probably be 10 p.m. That's only me working, and I'm expecting a long line. It's on the 35th floor of a building.
Wow. So no one knows you're there if they're just walking down the street.
Yes, I'm afraid of Mariah Gregory, so I'm trying to keep it under my hat. Or wig, as it were. LOL. Wig, as it were.
Wig, as it were.
Wig, as it were.
Oh, oh my God.
Oh, boy. Oh, Ted.
So we got the suicide on Fox News?
Yes. Some guy, it was one of these car chases. We've seen them all before.
Sure.
And they usually, you know, you're very excited, you're waiting for something to happen, and nothing happens. Well, this time something definitely.
It's the first time anything really good happened.
I know.
Why do you dislike a suicide video on YouTube? People just have to be just dicks, right?
Yeah.
Is that what that's about?
I think so, yeah.
It gets ridiculous after a while. How would you dislike that? What needed to be better in this video?
Yeah.
You already know it's a suicide video because it says it in the title, right?
Exactly.
So what did the guy do wrong that you had to dislike this? Right?
You shouldn't show that on the intranet.
I want to know why he killed himself because, you know, car chase, sure, they were closing in. He was going to get arrested, but he wasn't going to do that much time in the end, right?
Tell you what his warrant was. He might have had a warrant.
Maybe he had something big. Yeah. Why don't we know anything about the guy yet?
I don't know. Keeping it all on a QT.
I could watch this. It wasn't close up. I probably could watch this close up. We saw the Bud Dwyer. That's the most famous.
Oh, yeah, that's crazy.
Most famous live suicide ever.
This.
Want to play it over there or over here?
It's up to you.
Yeah, I'll play it over there so we can watch it, too.
Car chase.
Full screen.
Can we put this on our Facebook page? Because people were telling me all weekend they had a tough time finding this video.
We could, but they might take it down.
And I certainly tweeted this fucking video for everybody.
If this is on YouTube, this one?
Yeah.
I bet the actual shooting is blacked out. I bet they faded out.
You think?
I bet.
Okay. Let's find out.
Okay.
He is looking kind of erratic, isn't he?
Yes. Shepard Smith.
I don't know.
He's got a gun in his hand.
No. And look at this. He's just running. Oh, my. Well, it looks like he's a little disoriented or something. It's always possible guy could be on something.
There it is.
Oh, they showed it.
Get off it.
You know what?
He's a bull.
They should have shown that. You want to show the car chases?
Right.
Why would you're the news? Yeah. Why would you cut out?
Yeah.
Why are you showing the car accident? I mean, the car chasing.
Yeah.
They show you zipping 100 miles an hour through traffic, and yet all of a sudden, if somebody dies, we can't show that.
Well,
it's the phoniest fucking thing I've ever seen.
It's completely phony. They knew that they were going to air that.
Yeah.
You know, there's no other reason to show car chases, because us as viewers, we're looking at the car chase hoping that something crazy fucking happens. Right? You got to have the payoff.
Sure.
Absolutely.
That's news. I guess the action is the news, but if somebody shoots themselves, it's not viable news?
Right.
You showed the fucking towers coming down enough times.
Right,
yeah.
What, is this a little too close to what really happens?
And then they did the old apology?
Well,
the fake apology?
Yeah, Shep.
Well, some explaining to do. While we were taking that car chase and showing it to you live, when the guy pulled over and got out of the vehicle, we went on delay. So that's why I didn't talk for about 10 seconds. We created a 5-second delay, as if you were to bleep back your DVR 5 seconds. That's what we did with the picture we were showing you, so that we would see in the studio what was happening 5 seconds before you did, so that if anything went horribly wrong,
you missed
we'd
it
be
by
able
5
to cut
seconds?
Away from
That's
it
no way.
Without subjecting you to it.
No.
See,
and we really messed up.
And but why?
No. And we're all very sorry.
No, you didn't mess up.
That didn't belong on TV.
Yes, it did.
We took every precaution we knew how to keep that
up
from being on TV.
The guy is lying. You know how long 5 seconds is in TV and radio?
Long
He's
time.
Lying.
So everyone knew, like, okay, we can allow this to happen, but we have to cover our ass. He's seasoned. He knows this shit. So it's his whole job to be like, no, we can't do this.
Get off it, get off it.
There's so many lies here.
But again, it's like, they're so selected. They did not, no one cut away. Why did they cut away when the towers fell?
Yeah.
Why are they showing a plane
right.
when a plane's got a problem? Boy, the fucking news can't show that long enough
right.
that it might crash.
Right.
But if it crashes, then you're going to come off it?
Right.
Get the fuck out of here!
For showing you that.
They had every intention of showing it, and they needed Shepard Smith to play his role of, no, we can't show this.
I'm sorry I did that.
Five seconds to get off it. That's an eternity.
Yeah.
It's so phony.
Of course it is.
Show it. Hey, why are you sorry? People sat through the car crash. They get what they deserve.
Well, the phoniness is the apology thing.
Yeah.
Because they knew they were going to show this. There's no way.
Car chase, I meant.
Oh, yeah.
Every precaution we knew how to take to keep that from being on TV, and I personally apologize to you that happened. Sometimes we see a lot of things that we don't let get to you because it's not time appropriate, it's insensitive, it's just wrong. And that was wrong.
Shut up.
Yeah, but you don't believe
and
this.
That won't happen again on my watch.
Oh, shut really? The fuck
not
up
on my watch.
What happened with that guy and how that went down.
Too bad.
Tonight on the Fox Report.
Oh, see, and then they tease it.
Yeah,
now they're using it to tease.
Find out what happened to him tonight on the Fox Report.
Yeah, fucking, they're just phonies.
Yeah, they show embassy bombings. Everything else is okay.
They'll show another one.
Can't show it a little too close up.
Nope.
We want to talk about it.
I would love to know how many people jerked off that work at Fox News when that went down.
Yeah,
we got a good one.
I hate when they cut away. It means it's like you're encouraging people by showing the car chase. Then don't show the car chase.
Yeah.
How about this? Don't cut into regular programming to fucking whore a car chase.
Right.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
And I might have messed up over the weekend. I had good intentions. Everyone was searching for that video because it was being yanked off the internet, and I had a copy of it. And I tweeted, here's the video of the live suicide, and then I tweeted the wrong link. It ended up being the link to my basketball shot video.
Oh, see.
The Opester was hoping for some views.
Oh, Sam, do you just laugh at that?
The Opester's at it again. He's trying.
People were so pissed. Oh, hook, line, and sinker. Like, all right, here it is. I have it.
It's
the link to my stupid fucking basketball trick shot video.
The Opester's always got a trick up his
sleeve. Boy, were they mad.
The Opester's always got a new scam or swindle to get some more viewers on YouTube.
Look, I meant well. I meant well. I didn't mean well on that.
Shit.
I got confused. I was working on my YouTube channel and, you know.
Links got confused.
A little bit. A little bit, Sam. A little bit.
They hated me.
Oh, no doubt.
And you had a good tweet about this. It made a Reddit.
Oh, yeah. It made a Reddit.
What's the actual tweet? Made the front page of Reddit.
Well, I don't want to paraphrase. There, Samuel.
You know. Go to at Anthony Cumia.
Yeah, come on. What's the matter with you? What's the matter with you?
No, it did real well on Reddit. Reddit's a great site.
Yeah. Well, you got to go back 8,000 fucking tweets. You know, I tweet a lot.
Right. And I watched your helicopter video. I felt like I was in a hotel room.
Ooh, yeah.
It was very tranquil. I felt like I was going on a journey.
Journey.
I was going on a journey. And then I didn't realize you liked Duran Duran.
Who doesn't like Duran Duran?
But you went with a slow number for your helicopter video.
Yeah, I just picked
it was
anything
very tranquil.
To drown out the rotor noise.
Yeah.
But that one kind of kind of worked. Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
I tweeted, remember when Fox showed a guy shooting himself on live TV? If that was a nipple, we'd still be talking about how to protect the children. When a tit ends up on television, people lose their motherfucking minds. And believe me, I have no qualms about any of this being on TV. I'm not saying one is better or worse than the other.
Right.
I'd love everything on there. Please bring it.
Right.
Bring girls with their tits hanging out shooting themselves. I'll watch. But it's just amazing that people are so up in arms about sex and fucking the body being on TV. And there's a guy shooting himself in the head, and they apologize, you know, said it was a mistake. But there's no one's
cares.
Freaking out that the children are going to... My children were watching...
I want
I want all of it on TV as well, but I'll give you the father's perspective.
Oh.
I would much rather my kid sees a stupid nipple for half a second than a guy killing himself.
Right. Because then you got to explain all that.
Because they
shit.
Always talk about the children, like we've said a million times
the
on the show.
The children.
In my world, nah, man, show the nipples. I don't
yeah.
care. I could explain that to my kid.
It really is amazing, though, that's the thinking.
Actually, I would explain both to my kid, but I think he would be a little more horrified by that than a dumb nipple.
Yeah, and you got to explain why he would do something like
right,
that.
All that shit.
Where did he go? And
right.
Oh, why there's no Santa? Oh, sorry, kids. Yeah. Sorry.
My tweet did not make Reddit.
Oh,
what was yours, your Jimmy?
It's not worth it.
Jimmy.
Oh, Jimmy, what was it?
Oh. No, we really...
He got to talk him. He wants us to talk him into it.
It's so creepy.
No, I
can't. All right. If you insist.
All
but
right.
We didn't really insist yet, Jimmy.
He grabs his phone. He's like, all right.
We were working up to the insisting.
All right.
You got to give us a little time.
I have to act like I'm scrolling and it's not open to my tweet already. That's my fake scroll for some movement.
What was your tweet?
Since I'm embarrassed now. Fox News aired a live suicide the other day. First time I ever turned on the TV hoping to see Al Sharpton.
That's a good one. See?
That is good.
Did it make Reddit?
No.
Didn't make any sites?
That was a shame.
Made my Twitter.
Made your Twitter feed?
Yes, it did.
Twitter, the all-important Twitter.
All right, we should break then because we got Todd coming in. I haven't seen Todd in a while.
Todd Rosken, yeah.
Todd Rosken is a weird dude, man.
Yes, he is.
I like him, though.
I love Todd.
Don't get confused. He's weird, but I like him a lot. He's one of Dice's guys.
Yeah.
And he has this 15-minute film on Russ Meyer.
It's in the
or
New
Russ
York,
Meyer?
Russ Meyer, I think.
Meyer, right? Russ Meyer.
Is it in the film, the New York Film Festival tonight, I think? And he wants to get a feature made, but I think it's getting accepted into all these festivals.
It's well shot.
Yeah.
But it's obvious that it better be obvious because it seems to me it's like a little tease to get a film made about Russ Meyer. You know, the guy that did all those exploitation films.
Yeah.
Just big-titted women.
Big tits.
Those movies, you know, Mondo Topless. We've done hundreds of hours on Mondo Topless over the years. That guy.
So Super Vixens.
Yeah.
He did that one.
The acting was pretty good in the movie, too, right?
Yeah, I'm in love with the girl who played the lead. I have to know who she is. I guarantee you she's married or she has a baby or a fucking fiancé, but she was fantastic.
Big tit monster.
Oh, my God.
Big ones.
She looked like a girl from the late 60s, but really fucking hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's coming in to talk about Russ Meyer in this film, I guess. And I hope it's leading to a longer movie.
Yeah, I do
too. What's this, Sam?
I just got this text. There's Asian people reenacting my video on YouTube.
What? Waiting for an iPhone 5 for no reason. The parody version.
Well, yes.
But
this Asian guy just asked, what's the haps?
But we weren't talking about your video.
I got out
of
stuff.
Too late now. If he's big enough to get a parody video made, I want to hear it.
Well, and the guy with the fake Tourette's did a video for you, too.
I got a bunch of video responses.
You see the fake Tourette's guy?
Yeah. I saw that guy.
We haven't played him yet, either?
No.
Let me hear a little what this Asian guy's doing here.
We're here on the iPhone 5 line. I'm with Ray. Ray, what's the haps?
Well, everybody wants the new version of the iPhone 5, so we're all waiting in line.
Now, some people decided to do the silly thing and order it on the internet. So, what made you decide to wait in line?
Dude, they're just...
Well, I don't want to get ripped off by the internet, so I decided to wait in line.
What new features of the iPhone 5 that has you so excited?
It's Susan.
I'm not sure because I haven't seen it yet, but I'm pretty sure it would be like really cool to use. And,
she does a pretty good impression of her.
Yeah.
She's got
that guy's actually better than Sam.
Every day, like a laptop?
Actually, Apple has given me an iPhone 5 to show up for promotion. Would you like to see it?
Yes.
Oh, there's ad living. This isn't going to work.
Why are they doing it in front of traffic?
Why are they sitting down in the grass?
Big. I didn't know it was
what?
This
like
big.
Like broken bottles?
Hello?
They decided to go off on their own direction.
Yes,
awful. They
I'm going to piss my pants for this.
Oh, yeah, right?
All right, we'll do a quick break. Todd Rosken.
Yes.
Todd Rosken is next. Stay there.
Serious XM. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Let's get Todd Rosken in studio. He's a big star now. Big star. Todd Rosken.
There we go.
What's up, Todd?
Hello. How are you?
Take a seat.
Your girl can sit here if she wants to. Yeah, roll and tell her she can sit here if she wants.
Yeah, what are they?
Todd, you're on the air. They'll bring her in.
They'll put her in the fart room.
Usually we allow.
Relax, fart room.
We crack a window, it'll be all right. We don't allow usually guests like that, but she's, you know, she's your girl. Okay. It's different.
You sure? You sure we want her in here, Jimmy?
Okay. Yeah, she's nice.
You sure?
Yeah. Yeah, she's nice.
Hey,
Jimmy.
There we go.
Hello. Yeah, you can sit if you want. Just
yeah, take a seat.
All right. Yeah, she's not gonna be disruptive or anything.
She'll she just wants to be low key about things. You know, she's just fine.
Yeah.
All right.
What are you trying to do? Give you a hat?
Yeah.
You all right, Todd?
Yeah, very good.
All right, Todd. We met you years ago. Jimmy knows you more than I, but
yeah, absolutely.
I know you from Andrew Dice Clay, of course.
Yeah.
One of Dice's guys.
Yes, that's right. I was helping him out with some. Logistical stuff at that time.
Yeah.
You
still work with him?
No, actually, I haven't seen him in quite a while. I ran into him in...
Oh, yes, Kenny?
Todd,
I'm sorry to interrupt.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
But Andrew used to say that Todd was his invention.
What? What does that even mean?
I have no idea. I think maybe because we met in Los Angeles, and we happened to have been we grew up in the same neighborhood, were born in the same hospital in Brooklyn, New York, which is kind of weird. It's such a strange coincidence that you meet someone in Los Angeles and you end up having a connection, you know, that type of a connection. I think it was strange. It was same doctor delivered. I don't know. It was a weird thing, a strange coincidence. Mm.
What year was it that I knew you from? Because you always come to on the road. We were on the road together for a while.
You know, I'm horrible.
2000 or 99, around there, right?
About 2000, 2001. Yeah, about 2000, 2001.
Right.
That's right, Jim.
Wow.
I know Todd a long time. And I like the movie a lot. What's it called?
Up the Valley and Beyond.
Yeah, we like Russ Meyer. We're all fans of Russ Meyer here.
Oh, that's
I can't get enough of Mondo Topless. That's my movie.
That's an amazing movie.
Why is it amazing to you? Because to me, it's just like a bunch of girls with really nice tits.
That's it. You can just see bouncing giant breasts for an hour and a half. Giant buxotic, gravity-defying, huge... memories that are just like in your face. I've always wondered why he never ventured into 3D something like that, but he didn't need to because it was all right there in your face. That movie in particular, Mondo Topless, is like a phenomenal film because from a cinematic standpoint, technically, it's like an industrial film. Like, you know, you could do industrial films on IBM or industrial films on GM or whatever it is. He's doing it on breasts, and it's just silly with a narrator, and then and then there's these women doing this narration, voiceover, and these strange shots, crazy juxtapositions.
But it was sexy. It really, in front of the train as it's going by, with an awful radio and the train. Well, but the it was announcer, fucking sexy.
And the announcer brings it all together, like you said. What's his name again? We used to know his name. He died recently, a couple years back.
He had, I don't know, asked me that in Jersey, who was his narrator? And I he had the different narrators. I mean, Russ had done some on his own, he'd narrate, but I think Stuart Lancaster, maybe? Sure.
But
yeah,
just how he described the women was he had his own way.
It's like a free association.
Babette.
Yeah.
Babette, baby.
Right.
Crazy words. And Russ himself.
50-50 where it counts. Love that one.
Yeah. Mike makes right. It's like crazy.
I love that shit.
He's the best, man. Russ was just a
who's
hero.
Who's the girl? Who's the lead in this? Because she is fucking sexy, man. The girl who played his wife.
Sarah Jones. Yeah. I know.
Not
awesome.
I love her.
Yeah, she's on that new TV show. It's called Vegas with Dennis Quaid.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's in that show. And
the movie, it's only 15 minutes long. It left me wanting more. So are you trying to make a full-length feature on Russ Meyer?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
okay, this is sort of like
a teaser.
Let's get this out to the film festival to see if we can get some backing and some interest, right?
Yeah, and I never really, when we did this, I wasn't planning on getting into festivals because, there's certain criteria with a short film that you have to kind of follow. It's like, okay, it's 15 minutes, it's got to have a three-act structure, it's got to have, conflict resolution and all this kind of stuff. And we were like, okay, well, what would be like a snapshot of the feature, just like to hone in like one little aspect. And so we just did it kind of as an exercise, but we figured, okay, let's try to get into some festivals, get some exposure. Right. And it worked.
Now, what I learned about Russ Meyer, he was in the war, comes back, and what? He just didn't know what he wanted to do with his life?
Well, he was a war photographer in the 166, during World War II, and stationed overseas, and he shot footage for General Patton, and he was always into photography. His mother bought him his first camera when he was a kid, and it's something that he just had this great eye and this propensity for naturally. And he's
How does that lead to I'm going to film women with tits?
Because
it seems like if he was that talented, he probably could have went off in a bunch of other directions. What was it about the man where he had to go down that road with this?
It was his compulsion. He was just drawn to giant mammaries. It was a strange, not really strange. I don't blame the guy, and I'm glad he did it. It was his obsession. And
you think he banged these girls after he photographed them?
A lot of times, and I think that may have had to do with like him and his wife splitting, who remained his producing partner even after they broke up. After the war, World War II, he did industrial films.
He started with just photography.
Just photography, that's true. And
were those pictures?
He did pinup photography for like pre-Playboy.
Right.
And the compositions are gorgeous. I mean, they're real. He just like had a way of those guys. They're like masters of composition.
Can we find some Russ Meyer photos there?
They're really beautiful and extremely sexy and very provocative without being like...
Showing the pig.
There you go. Exactly right.
If you made this movie, would you use this 15 minutes in it, or would you have to reshoot this stuff?
This is like an extrapolation of one of many themes much further explored in the feature film. And it's, we would use some of this. We'd reshoot everything.
Oh, you do? Okay.
The entire thing.
God damn it. Absolutely. That's hot.
Whoa.
That's later. That's actually his third wife, Edie Williams.
Really? Wow, she's lovely.
She was in Beyond the Valley of the Dolls.
Big muff.
Yeah, she's looking down her thong into her like she probably thought an actual animal crawled into her underpants. Oh, no, it's just my pussy. It's 1968.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I'm living in 1968.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, right. That's like... Beyond the Valley Dolls, it's 70, something like that.
Right.
Yeah, that's Edie Williams. That's right. Oh, she's these are hot. Great.
So he does the pinups, and then he decides, you know what, I think I could make some films. Because
exactly
this
right.
is pre-porno.
That's right.
This is pretty much the first mainstream porno.
That's right. This is pre-porno.
Look at her ass.
Gorgeous.
It's really a plump. Like these women, I love the bodies on these women because they have real heavy tits and real tits and plump bottoms. I don't like the hairy vag, but I love their natural bottoms. And
God, you're right over there.
It's true, yeah. No, okay. Oh, wait, can you go up a little bit? Adam Magazine. So Adam Magazine was one of the early...
Wow.
You know,
that's pre-Playboy, obviously.
Pre-Playboy, one of the, you know.
I never heard of Adam Magazine.
Early girly magazine.
She was like Monroe. She was like Marilyn Monroe.
That's, what's her name? June Wilkinson? She was a gorgeous, gorgeous model. Russ photographed her a lot, and that was one of his models. Yeah, and then...
Banged her?
Probably. this guy, he...
He was a horn dog, huh?
He was definitely out there doing what he loved doing the most, and that was... But he didn't allow sex... with the actors when they were filming.
Because he wanted to fuck them.
Exactly. And he wanted them just aching for sex before he rolled cameras. So he didn't allow any of that on set. But except those rules didn't apply for him, of course. He did. Exactly. So this was pre-Playboy. And then he met his wife, Eve Turner. And he actually shot her for Playboy and did centerfolds in 55.
She was fucking beautiful. Sarah Jones.
Is that Eve?
Hot.
That's Eve right
there. Oh, look at her. She's on the couch with her fucking rump sticking up in the air.
Make that bigger there. I've seen that picture before.
You seen that one?
Yeah, yeah. I think I scrapped that one a few times.
Look at her ass. Oh, is she fantastic? Her little big feet are on the ground.
What? She's just playing a few records.
Man.
Yeah, she's just hanging out.
Some records of the day.
Just with a little shirt on and then no panties or anything. And she's kind of got her ass poking up in the air.
I don't like the way he shot her foot, though, because the color blends into the paper. It looks like she has a flipper. Like, That's a terrible foot shot.
You don't like the flipper foot?
No, but it's only the ankle. You can't see where the ankle, the form of the ankle. So it looks like she's a fat flipper ankle.
That's a great shot to just come screaming in from the left-hand side and swoop your face right in.
Oh, look at her. Fuck it. Her hiney's so plump. She says, kiss me. I eat thongs.
Fuck. Oh, man.
Yeah, totally sorry. Wow. You know.
What else can you tell us about Russ Meyer?
Looks good.
Russ Meyer, he just loved...
show me the color
version. High-perched... Look, yeah, that's Eve right there.
Is she dead?
Yeah, she died in a plane crash, unfortunately, like 1977. It's crazy, it's insane.
Oh, look at her fucking body.
Oh, like, man.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Does Sarah Jones have a body like that?
I didn't see her body, actually, like, quite to this extent. I mean, she's very, very well proportioned.
She married?
She has a boyfriend.
Yeah, why wouldn't she?
Yeah, she's real, and such a great actress. Really, really great actress.
Yes.
Very, very cool.
Plane crash.
Yeah. And Jim Parrick was Russ Meyer, and he did a great job.
He was great.
Yeah, he loves this show. He's like a big fan of all you guys.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's going to be in town for the movie.
He's a good actor, man.
On the 14th, and he said
Would he play Russ Meyer in the feature if you get it?
I would love to have him play Russ Meyer, absolutely. He can definitely do that.
Would Sarah be in?
I would love to have her also. She's awesome. She's such a real, real, real great actress, real serious thespian. Yeah. You know?
That fucking Eve's body in that color photo is awesome.
Yeah, that's a good
That's
one
Eve right up top.
That's her right there, right?
I don't know. I don't think that's Eve,
actually.
Oh,
girl.
She's above that one. If you
what
go
a
back,
wonderful.
Two up.
She recreated
that
the
color
shot.
One, that's Eve.
Jesus. I like the one on the couch better, but that fucking ass is so juicy. You just want to put your face there and just sniff.
did Eve do any mainstream acting, or was it all...
She did. She was in Russ's, like, one of, you know, his early film, Eve and the Handyman.
Eve and the Handyman?
That's not a mainstream movie.
What is that about? No, that's about, I think, as far as her acting career went, maybe like one... It's kind of like a silent film. And
did
like
you see it?
Yeah, I saw like most all of us. He did so many films. There's tons of information on this guy. It's because he did so much.
Is Even the Handyman a good movie?
It's cute. It's very clever. It's interesting.
Can we get a clip from Even the Handyman, Sam?
Yeah, it's like
Even the Handyman.
It's like French New Wave. I don't know. Cinematic terms, it's like a Jacques Tati type film. It's
very
clever.
Of course, we all know that.
All that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I'm
with
It's more like It's an elegant type of portrayal of absurdity.
Man is always looking for new worlds to conquer.
Great.
Make it bigger, Sam, so I can see this wonderful.
Ooh, it's a
talkie.
It's a space feature. We're going to the moon.
In this, the age of outer space, man is always looking for new worlds to conquer.
Strap on.
What's that? He's a handyman. Yeah.
To what end, I wonder? Had my man anticipated what he might come up against, I don't think he would have risked his neck with that devil-may-care bravery.
Devil-may-care.
It's just a handyman in the window.
But at the same time, I had to carry my share of danger as well.
She's a sexy way of talking.
Yes. This is so old.
There's her feet are propped up.
On a typewriter.
Right.
Her legs.
Hubba hubba.
Behind like a desk. She has great legs. She's throwing things at the garbage can and missing.
Yes. She can't really see the garbage pail.
Yeah.
And we can't see her.
Handyman's enjoying the view.
We just see her stems and the paper fly.
Well, doll.
Yeah.
He's going to pick up the paper.
Yes. He's a cuckold.
Handyman.
He's a cuckold.
Yeah. Those are cum tissues. He's picking them up and eating them. Oh. Now he's addressing Eve.
Oh, good God.
She's wearing glasses.
Oh,
and she
my
has,
God.
Her face is a little dicey in this one. Oh! But she has really great tits.
I think it's just because of the glasses.
Yeah.
No, I didn't. Like, her face isn't bad at all.
She looks a little like Marion in this. That's her. There she is.
Oh, God. Yeah. She looks pretty good.
Now he's climbing out the window. Wow, yeah, she's pretty.
That's really hot right
what
there.
What a set of jugs.
Yeah. I would scrap to that.
Oh, man.
She's not even new.
Yeah, the whole thing with these types of movies is a tease.
Jimmy, look at this.
There she is.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God.
I would give her bosoms a nuzzling. Music's amazing. Wow. It's basically just this guy climbing out the window, and they keep focusing in on her giant tits.
That's it.
A lot of cleavage showing.
She is a pretty girl, actually. The glasses are awful. She's putting a pencil in her mouth, which is kind of like a cock. Too bad it wasn't a darker pencil, but she's looking through a little teeny binoculars at the handyman.
Yeah, there's some woman on the street watching the handyman.
Well, the handyman might have a raging boner at this point.
Yeah, he does. He's leaking clear stuff onto the window.
Oh, he is. Look at him.
Yeah, and he's spraying stuff on the window to clean
it. He's going
to
wash the windows. And she's right there.
Yeah, and he's looking inside the window. Big fucking tits. She's on a typewriter chewing gum, and he's on the window outside just staring at her fucking giant tits. How about they stop showing the handyman and show the tits?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's our only complaint, Todd.
There you go.
Oh, boy.
They're jiggling because she moves when she types.
They want to be free.
Oh, my God.
And he wants them to be
fucking
free.
Fucking heavy. And meanwhile, he's smudging soap on the window so he can't see them.
Yeah, that's
what
smart.
A dunce.
What a
idiot.
Dumb handyman.
Is this a Russ Meyer movie?
This is Russ's film. Yeah, this is 1959. Old.
59?
59?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know it was that
right.
old.
Oh, yeah, right? It's got a modern look. It could be, you know.
That was his war buddy, James Ryan.
Wow.
I met that guy.
59?
Yeah, 59.
People probably crazy. Jerked off to this like animals back then.
Crazy.
Easily.
The handyman.
Wow.
How much longer is the clip?
Yeah, this is endless.
This is, I think, the whole movie.
Hey, you got a clip of the handyman?
Oh, we'll play it out. It's only like 30 more seconds.
Where did you... You had to like go to the movie theater to watch this, though.
Yeah.
They call it the Raincoat Brigade.
The Raincoat Brigade?
Yeah, they go into the hardtop and they go in there with trench coats and check out these films.
Wait a minute. What?
His job is done.
Yeah.
But he can't move away from the window.
Oh, I don't blame him.
Staring.
Those big buxotic tits.
And she's on the typewriter.
Yeah.
That was hardcore porno back
then. He didn't need to be, he didn't need to have the harness on and the safety gear and stuff because he was all on the ground floor. By the roof.
Right.
So he just stepped off. He just did that so he could look down at her tits.
Oh, that was a better reveal than Kaiser Soze.
He definitely had a unique style.
He did. He did.
I'm sure there were a bunch of guys doing that same thing, but we don't know their names.
Yeah, there was like that sexploitation movement that went on, you know, in the late 50s, 60s, and 70s, earlier 70s, and there was a few other ones, Radley Metzger and what's his name? Friedman, but he was the one. Russ was the
guy. What years did he work? From when to when?
I think that his last. He did a film with Pandora Peaks, which was like after his the main thrust of his career. The last feature that he did was written by Roger Ebert, Beneath the Valley of the Ultra
Basins, of course, yeah.
With Kit Natividad and that's a
Kit Natividad.
I forgot that he wrote that.
Yeah.
Beneath the Valley of the Dolls.
He wrote three
of the
Ultra
Basins.
Beyond the Valley of the Dolls.
Yeah, the Valley of the Dolls.
And beneath the Ultra Basins. Right. Yeah, exactly right.
Roger Ebert wrote those, mm-hmm. And he's fucking judging other people's movies.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
It's wild. Yeah, he's a brilliant guy. Amazing.
Who?
Roger Ebert.
When did Russ die?
He died like 2004.
Oh, just recently?
Yeah, recently.
And what did Eve die in a plane crash going from... What was she doing?
Canary Islands. I don't know what the heck she was going over these Canary Islands. Crazy situation. It was like one of the most horrific plane crashes. It's insane.
Was it that... Was it that crazy one with the fucking two 747s that collided on the runway?
I think that was
Canary Islands, right? Yeah. Wow, that was crazy. I think that's still the biggest airline fucking fatality in the history of the world.
Probably so. Yeah.
Was that the one?
I think
Samuel?
So.
That's one on the runway, right? There was
one was taking off.
It was a Pan Am flight.
Was taxiing, and it's two 747s. Takeoff speed rammed right into another one.
Wow. One of 335 passengers killed. It's the deadliest.
Was she in first class?
It doesn't say.
Let me see a picture of her.
What year was this?
Wow, she's fucking gorgeous.
What year was this?
77?
77? Yeah,
okay. How ironic. Her tits look like the two noses of the 747s. Big.
I don't know.
Nice, firm.
I'd love to suck her big tits.
Yeah. You pick them off the runway?
I would have. While the firemen were working, I'd just be holding up a tit, sucking like a fucking kid's juicy drink.
Oh, that's terrible. Jesus.
Oh, geez. I hope you don't mind over there. Hope she doesn't mind. And right now?
She kind of minds. Yeah, right?
Is it crazy, right? Having to deal with this?
Yeah. No, it's cool.
I hear you. She just phases out of the whole thing. She's like, nah, I'm good. Fucking Todd's
funny. He's absolutely wild.
Yeah. Wow, yeah. That's cool. Wow.
It's all right. You make boobies there, Todd.
Yeah. So we're getting geared up to do the feature, and there's.
You think you got a shot at this feature?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Got some interest already?
Yeah. I was speaking with Joe Berlinger. You know, he did Paradise Lost. You know the.
We've had those guys in.
Yeah, he told me about that, and he wants to get involved and do the producing of it, and we're gearing up here.
Well, you captured the essence of Russ in your short film.
Oh, cool.
Absolutely, you did.
Oh, good.
Just how it was filmed and all that. So,
right, yeah.
I think you're onto something there, Todd.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Thanks, Opie. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's really cool.
Now, put you in get the hell out of here.
Put in a word for me with Sarah. Tell you know somebody, a comedian who's single.
Sure.
There's a lot going on.
Oh.
Right, yeah.
A lot going on.
Maybe get Jim in your feature.
Right, right.
You got a role for Jim Norton?
Absolutely.
You do?
Yeah. There's a role for Jim, and I've always thought of Jim for the role. Yeah, that he's...
A buttered one.
Carbs.
Jesus.
Yeah, definitely.
I think I'm going to watch some Russ Meyer today because of you.
Do it.
Nice, yeah.
He's the man.
That's so where cool. can people Absolutely. See this, by the way?
This is going to be at the... at Lincoln Center, it's the New York Film Festival, and it's going to be playing today at 1 p.m. at the Film Center, and then on the 14th at the the Walter Reed Theater at Lincoln Center also on October.
How long is the film festival?
I think the 14th is the last day.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
it's a couple weeks. Yeah,
get Sarah Jones in here.
Yeah,
love
yeah,
to talk to her.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Sarah, what's up?
Yeah,
there she is.
Even the artwork looks like a Russ Meyer thing.
You're like, cool. Thank you. Yeah,
Up the Valley and Beyond is the name of Todd Rosken's film.
How long have you been obsessed with him?
Oh, geez, a long time, 10 years.
So you like big tits too, huh?
Yeah, what's not to like about them?
Sometimes they smell like lamb if they're sweaty.
Oh God.
They do. Sometimes if big tits get sweaty, they stop.
Todd, have you noticed that?
Lamb?
That they could smell like lamb?
I've yet to experience them in that capacity, but... but little mint sauce. Can't hurt. I don't know. So, this is so great. This is a lot of fun to be on the radio. It's wild.
Oh, it's a pisser.
This is wild?
Genuine to wild.
It's insane, you know?
It's insane. Crazy. Yeah. Why is it insane?
I don't know. You talk on the radio. It seems kind of it's a strange experience. Or
it's strange because you don't even know if anyone's listening.
Right. It's like we're
I'll never
this,
get
like,
used to that.
Realm.
You have no idea where this goes.
Yeah, you just have a conversation to these things. No one tells me these are even plugged in. You're just talking.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, having a conversation in front of some electronic equipment makes you think you're a big star.
I'm always assuming no one's listening. So yeah, I assume
you got it. You got to assume no one's listening. Yeah. And then if you find out someone was, it's kind of cool.
Cool.
Nice, right?
Good. Yeah, definitely.
That's a monolith.
I know. What a big girl.
I like that.
Walking down the hallway.
Yeah.
A buxotic.
Yeah. Big long-haired
buxotic.
Dixon.
Yeah.
So are we done for today?
Yeah, Todd, I think we're done.
Cool. All right. Guys, thanks very much for having me on. It's
oh,
awesome.
No problem.
It's
that shit's great.
It's cool. Thanks.
Yeah.
Thank
Love
you.
It.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's he was the best, man. Russ Meyer rules. It's so great that you guys are familiar with his movies and are and interested in his art, you know, all his films.
Oh, we call it art.
That's so cool.
Call it jack-off material.
Dude, that fucking... Yeah, yeah. That girl's
you
ass
could,
on
you
that
could look
sofa.
At the artistic part of the whole thing.
Wow.
As a filmmaker.
There's many different ways to to appreciate...
right, exactly.
the films, the film cinematic world of Russ Meyer.
You think that girl on the sofa is deader than a motherfucker right now? She probably is.
Oh, probably.
What year do you think that photo was taken?
70s?
No.
Oh, yeah, that one on the sofa? Oh, but there was two on the sofa. The one was a color, one was a black and white.
The black and white, I'm at the color one.
Color one was probably 70s.
That's a white girl.
Okay. I would think so, yeah. But the black and white, I don't know.
I got it.
Yeah.
I got it.
All right.
All right, Todd Rosken.
Cool.
You got a Twitter or anything, or what are we doing?
We have upthevalleyandbeyond.com. Right. And there's a Facebook page up at the Valley and Beyond. And you can, from the website, you can get around to all that kind of stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
a pretty good recreation of the two girls there. They did a good job.
Oh, look at that. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Wow.
And they figured out that the foot needed to be different.
Yes.
Jimmy, see?
Yes.
Jimmy look. Was onto something.
You were right.
They lifted
the
foot
and
that recreation.
They said, yeah, we got to move that
girl.
Foot.
No, it's not.
No?
No, it's two girls. They reenacted
two different
it.
Girls.
And they said, yeah, that right foot
this
needs
one might
to be
that
different.
Might be Eve Turner on the bottom, the black and white.
Yeah.
Interesting. Right.
Cool. We're going home, Todd.
All right.
If you want to stay
all right,
here, you're
man.
Welcome.
All right. Oh, yeah. Hang out with Sam.
Hang out with Sam.
Love it.
All right. I guess that's it, right?
Cool. All right.
I have one plug.
Up for the Valley and Beyond.
I just have one plug. October 19, Vegas, in Henderson Club Madrid again, and October 25 through 27, Helium in Philly. Thursday show has been added, so there's now six shows. They will probably all sell out.
Very good. I guess nice. Todd, fucking Kenny should have told me ahead of time. You helped out with Autofocus, the Bob Crane movie?
I produced that, yeah. I co-wrote it and produced it.
Oh, wow.
It. Yeah, yeah.
Damn. With who?
Who I co-wrote it with a friend of mine.
No, was that the Greg Kinnear?
That was the Greg Kinnear film, yeah. Was,
holy
Paul Schrader directed it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool, yeah. It's about Bob Crane, yeah.
And he was
Bob Crane was a
he
wild
was a pervert.
Yeah, that guy was nuts.
He liked his cameras.
He totally liked
and
his
you produced
cameras.
That?
Yes, I did. Yeah.
Who do you think did it? You think it was...
I think it was Carpenter.
Carpenter,
I think so. I mean, it kind of like
Carpenter.
John Carpenter was his friend.
Not that John Carpenter.
It was a different...
Well, it seemed like they might have been more than friends, though, there, Todd,
something
right?
was going on. I mean, that was, like, you know...
There's a lot of sharing going on.
A lot of sharing.
Video,
A lot of... yeah, exactly. A lot of alcohol and his, you know, parties, you know, kind of...
Goddamn,
certain things.
Hogan would fucking wheel out all this video. You know what video equipment was like back then?
Yeah.
It wasn't just a fucking little camcorder you hold in your hand, little
like a
flip cam.
Yeah.
This is giant equipment with the reel-to-reel fucking thing you needed to sit there on a... And he would wheel all this stuff out and have sex with women on video.
Sure.
You couldn't. It wasn't covert. You couldn't hide these things.
I was going to say, it sure made it hard getting upskirts.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Willem
right?
Dafoe was in that one, too.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
He
this Todd is the real deal, producing Autofocus.
That's fucking cool.
That means this Russ Meyer film will be done. You got a good track record.
Very cool.
Oh, I'm excited. Yeah. I can't wait to see the, you know, the Russ Meyer film, the whole
cool.
thing.
Thanks.
All right, with that, we're out of here.
See
Todd Rosken,
awesome.
Thank you, sir. And
thanks,
Sam is going to continue next with who? I don't know.
Oh,
he'll do something.
Whatever he does.
Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show, the venomous voices of the vastly vulgar airwaves. Introducing the Destroyer, operator of the OCD organization Opie. The Professor, the know-it-all neurotic Nancy Anthony. Swing over to little Jimmy Dorton, the worthless chinless buxom master of laugh. Meet the irritating extra of excrement E-Rock. And don't forget Sam, black and white, 50-50. Where it counts. Corrupting the cavities of ear holes everywhere. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Opie and Anthony!
Fuck. The Opie and Anthony Show is pretty much over.
Pretty much over. Pretty much over.
But if you feel like sticking around after 1A Live is next.
Next.
Serious XM. Anthony Show continues. This is After ONA Live. Here's your host, Sam Roberts.
Yep. It's After Open Anthony Live. There's a weird Eastern European looking man who's pacing outside the studio right now. He's got one of those earpieces in, the iPhone earpieces. And he's just walking back and forth. He's bald and he's wearing a sweater. Feel like I'm in the movie Taken. If anything goes down, if you guys start hearing anything weird, I want all the listeners to pay attention to the voices, because that's what saved, you know, Liam Neeson's kid. He knew the voices. There's got to be one of you out there. Come on in, Jenny Hutt. There's got to be one of you out there that's like a CIA specialist or something. I mean, I guess if Jenny Hutt made it in, probably we're safe. Did you say? No, I was just saying there's a weird Eastern European looking guy who was pacing outside a minute ago.
I didn't see him.
Like Taken. Exactly. You'll never see him.
Oh, he's like
wait, I'm just checking my email. Sorry.
Until it's too late. Well, no, why would you make this a priority? I'm sure there's something really important going
there
on.
There isn't.
In your email.
My issue is I ordered from Energy Kitchen and they're going to call to say it's downstairs.
Well, tell them to bring it up here.
They can't get through security.
Whatever. What are they packing in that food? Anyway.
Yes.
I also wanted, we had Todd Rosken in today. Do you know who Russ Meyer is?
No, who's Russ Meyer?
Oh, my God. He's a great filmmaker from, like, the 60s. And he made all these, like, weird tit-centered B-movies.
Like, boobie-centered?
That's right.
Mean?
Oh, yes. Breasts. Of the time.
Right. Yeah.
My favorite Russ Meyer movie is Faster Pussycat Kill Kill.
Oh.
I could watch that movie at any point in any day. It's a great movie.
All right.
But it's just weird. It's just about chicks... And they're fighting each other, and they drive cars fast.
But isn't it all just meant to show their boobs and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's like Todd said when he was in here. It's all a tease. You never actually see their boobs.
Oh.
They're just in very low-cut shirts.
It implies almost breasts and will surface.
And they're driving fast, and they're terrible fight scenes. It's an awesome movie, but Todd produced a film about Russ Meyer. And it debuts today, if you want to check it out. It's at 1:30 p.m. at Lincoln Center here in New York. So
I'll be on the air for that.
Nobody's going to... Come on. It's a 15-minute movie. You can't leave your show at 1:30.
Nope. Can't do it.
Is there a best of, or is that not possible with a one-hour show?
No, there's not. Yeah, no. On occasion, I have to have a best of, yeah, but not today.
Let's go straight to Larry.
Oh, boy.
In Ohio, because I'm not going to let Larry go without being answered. Larry, welcome to After Opie and Anthony Live.
Hollywood Primetime, Sammy Sweetheart Roberts, talking all the technical terms. That's why you are Hollywood Primetime, Sammy Sweetheart, and I digress. The effing Roberts, you are the man. I really have to take issue with you about something you said yesterday. You cut me to the quick.
I cut you to the quick. I hate
to
do that.
Harsh.
On the Sunday show, of course. See, Jenny Hutt, you don't have loyal callers like this.
Well, I do.
No, you don't have people who spend 30 seconds introing you with this long nickname that they've created for you.
Well, they haven't given me a nickname, but they can be super nice.
Not this nice.
Well, but then you cut them to the quick.
Larry, how did I...
Is that like cutting him to the core as well?
No, of course not. Larry, how did I cut you to the quick?
Sammy, it went straight to my heart when you said that I think you're great. You said you have guys who think you're great.
Yeah.
Sam, I know you're great.
And you've been holding on to that since yesterday.
This is not subjective. This is an opinion. It is fact. You are the man, the man. You
Larry.
Are so great. People believe you're a myth. They didn't think anyone could ever achieve your greatness.
Right.
And you are already a legend. That's why you are the man, the myth, the legend.
You're making me blush.
Wow.
Well, what did you learn today, Larry?
Any less true. I learned today that the boys signed their contract.
Yeah.
Except for little Jimmy. Little Jimmy's language wasn't perfectly correct to suit him, so he did not sign his contract.
That's right. That's good, Larry. Thank you for calling in, as always. And that is, I mean, Jim seems optimistic that he's going to sign his contract soon. There's just some kind of last-minute thing going on that he couldn't clear up over the weekend. But their contract expired today. Nobody really knew for sure. They weren't signed on Friday. That's legit. As of Friday, when they left here, no contracts were signed. Ant tweeted something out over the weekend about signing something, but I didn't know. And I didn't know if they had both signed, but finally we learned this morning at the top of the show that not only had they signed, if you remember 2 years ago when they signed their contract, it was like 5 minutes before they went on the air. And the first hour of that new contract was complaints about what a shitty deal they had gotten.
But this year, probably a better deal.
This year, it sounded like a very good deal.
Yeah.
Which makes me think there's money being thrown around this place. And if there's money being thrown around this place,
it's coming your way.
I'm putting on my catcher's glove.
Let me see how that works for you.
I'm going to get a lot of it. Tons of it.
I believe in you, Sam.
Thank you, Jenny Hutt. Dave in Long Island?
Yeah, hi, Sam.
Hi.
So now you don't have to go to Plan B.
Well, here's the thing. Plan B was kind of ended. Plan B was to be a YouTube viral star. That's already happened.
It worked.
But it's over now. Now it's the decline. Now I'm in the.
I'm very excited for you, well, Sam.
I'm in the behind the music of YouTube stardom where it's
now
over.
Now that the contracts have been signed, I'm looking forward to seeing all those naked women prancing around in your bigger, newer studio with old cameras and lights that are going to be installed.
But no, I don't know if. I mean, to my knowledge, I don't believe there will be a new studio, and there certainly probably won't be any cameras.
Are they redoing this one?
No, I wouldn't think so.
Okay.
Yeah, at least you got rid of the babysitters, right? That's on the contract.
I don't know babysitters, but to my knowledge, management will remain. The structure of management will not be changed.
Oh, so how about advertising? Are they going to advertise your show now, maybe? Or
hopefully.
No?
No, I mean, I don't know if that the language in the contract
so
specifies.
Basically, the only thing that they signed was maybe they got some more money.
And let's hear it for that.
Everything else is going to be the same then.
Well, they've earned it.
Yeah, but they'll be richer people, and hopefully they'll be happier to entertain
you. Richer as far as they were making more at XM, and then they pretty much got a cut.
Dave, I don't know what you do for a living.
If they get more, they're actually getting less than they used to get.
I don't know what you do for a living, but if being a radio person's agent was ever something that you thought about doing, that's something you should consider. You'd be very, very good at it.
He's convincing me.
How about putting 105 on Sirius as well as XM so people that own a Sirius could actually hear you guys?
You know what you should do?
Is that in the contract?
Make a list of your concerns.
I have a list.
You do.
You have a list. How about allowing...
You're like Patton Oswalt in the fan movie, whatever that psycho sports fan movie that...
John.
Is that too hurtful?
What's that?
I'm gonna cut you to the quick
and hang up on you now. Listen, I'm understanding that Dave in Long Island is not happy about Opie and Anthony's new contract, but I believe Opie and Anthony are happy about Opie and Anthony's new contract. So that's all that we can hope for. Another "What did you learn?" is coming from Sonny Farrelly, who's got to be happy for. We learned it's a 2-year contract. Two more years of Opie and Anthony are guaranteed.
Hey, you know, what I learned today was Katie Sunshine's husband isn't really too much of an undercover officer.
That's a great point, Sonny. Yeah, he's not really an undercover narc anymore, is he?
No, especially where Jimmy's got a picture of her.
Thank you, Sonny. I don't know, have you seen this Katie Sunshine, Jenny Hutt?
No, who's Katie Sunshine?
She is very hot and dances with a hula hoop.
Oh, I did see that video.
And now she's a huge viral star.
I like Kate Upton. I think she's super sexy.
You've been, yeah, but she's not a viral star. She's British royalty.
She's just a star.
Yeah.
No, Kate Upton, not Kate, not Catherine.
Who's it?
Isn't Kate Upton the hot?
Eric, who's Kate Upton? Isn't that the?
She was on the cover of Sports
Illustrated. Oh, right.
She's like the sexiest girl.
Why do you like her?
I just think she's the hottest body of, like, all girls.
Like, are you a lesbian?
No. I just
do you have lesbianic tendencies?
I don't. I've
are
never
you bi curious?
No.
Then why do you like her?
Because she's beautiful. I think she's sexy, like, empirically sexy.
Yeah, but, I mean, there are handsome dudes that I'm not like, oh, man, I love that
but
guy.
You don't
he's
know
so
if a guy
handsome.
Is but you know if he's handsome.
Like, I'm not sitting there going, you know, Eric Nagel, he's a handsome son of a bitch.
No,
I love that guy.
Here's what it is. I don't, that girl from the hula hoop
But he's
hoop
the
video,
handsomest guy I know.
But the hula hoop video girl I didn't think was.
Did you see her in yoga pants?
I saw her hula hooping.
Wait, with yoga pants on?
Whatever she was in. What at that outdoor festival
if you
thing.
If you saw her with the yoga
by
pants
and
on,
she's hula hooping.
I would assume you'd be attracted to her.
No, I'm not attracted to girls. Like, I have no interest in touching
well, you like
their
Kate
parts.
Upton.
I think she's hot.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You were part of this last year. Jocktober started.
Oh, here we go again.
Today.
Oh, brother.
It's Jocktober 1st.
Here
Jenny
we go.
Hutt.
Yeah.
And Jenny Hutt has a show here on SiriusXM.
I do.
It's only an hour long.
That's right.
But
are you trying to hurt me?
No, because you pack so much into that
I
hour.
I do.
It's
and
amazing.
Then I do a second show. I mean, I don't like 12 shows like you do, but I have a second show on Thursdays as well.
What show is that?
It's called John Hines TV Show.
Howard 101. You just talk about TV shows.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's the thing. I got to do some of those shows where you're just like, oh, I watch TV. Let's do a show. Oh, it's fun.
Well, my show is fun. I like doing my show every day.
What do you
day,
do on your show now?
I talk.
Because you, Jenny Hutt, is the one. A couple years ago, she came on because she used to do a show.
Not a couple years ago. It was here like 6 months ago.
Yeah, but the first time, right? It's probably a couple years ago.
Oh, yeah, probably.
Right.
Sure.
And if you remember, she used to do a show with Martha Stewart's daughter until Martha Stewart's daughter decided she was a horrible person and didn't want to talk to her ever again.
Are you referring to me or to her? I'm confused.
No, she decided, Martha Stewart's daughter decided you were a horrible person and never wanted to talk to you ever again.
Yeah, that's true. I think that did happen.
And,
I don't think
and,
it was that she decided I was a horrible person. I just think she just didn't like me anymore. But that's okay.
But why don't you like somebody, generally speaking, because they're a horrible human being?
I don't know. It sort of depends on who you are.
But,
different people and friendships for different reasons.
So she got you thrown off Martha Stewart Radio.
I'm not going to say that, but ultimately I did leave Martha's channel. And
it's
that
the beauty
sense.
Of it was that Jenny she left the show that she was doing with Jenny. Martha Stewart's daughter did.
Right.
And so Jenny was just doing the show by herself.
Yes.
And then that wasn't good enough for Martha Stewart's daughter. She then went and got Jenny Hutt thrown off Martha Stewart Radio.
Listen, the good news is that then
Sirius Eric, that's
XM
the way it happened, right? You know how it goes around here. That's
how I heard it.
Okay, okay. And he knows the gossip.
Yeah, well,
but then they brought you on.
Sirius XM then hired me, which is great. Because I had been working for Martha Stewart's company, but now I work for Sirius XM. And yes, they put me on Stars.
Right.
107. Right.
Now, have you talked to Martha Stewart's daughter since then?
No, God, no. Uh-uh.
You haven't called her and been like,
oh, what's
listen,
there to say?
How about stop being a bitch and throwing me off radio channels?
No, it's like all okay. I'm happy to be on the air. It doesn't really matter how
as
and
Joe
when
Joe DeRosa
happened.
Said, you're fucking with my livelihood.
I'm all right. I'm going to be okay because I'm scrappy and I work hard and I'll keep doing what I like to do.
Well, you've survived. You
so
survived
far, so good.
The
Thanks.
Onslaught. And you had to deal with the onslaught that everybody with Jocktober is dealing with now.
Oh, brother.
Jocktober, as of last year, became a very interactive thing.
Okay.
Where not only do you remember Jocktober?
I
we,
do.
We make
yeah,
fun
we
of radio
do
shows.
This now. Really?
Yeah. We make fun of radio shows.
Okay.
For no reason.
Mm-hmm.
And then as of last year, fans started leaving terrible comments on the Facebook pages of these radio shows.
That did happen.
So they were all.
But they
all,
changed
all...
it because the timeline now right. is better. Because
no, it's not. We got a Facebook page shut down again today.
Oh God.
Yeah, so it's not that much better. We destroy them.
Well, I'd love your fans to follow me on Twitter at Jennifer Hutt.
Right.
That'd
but what
be
I,
super.
What I was gonna say was
what. They could also go to justjenny.com. I think I'm doing Gangnam Style with Elmo on my homepage.
That's not going to be hula-hooping sexy, but it'll be fun.
On the treadmill. When I walk on the treadmill, I have cleavage. Isn't
okay.
that good enough?
But.
What?
They got all riled up and didn't understand last year the difference between somebody who's just a friend of the show stopping by
yeah.
versus somebody we're attacking.
I think you guys encourage that sort of confusion.
Don't say you guys, because I was not one of them.
No, not you.
Is it rough? Is it rough when the Jocktober hit happens?
It isn't. It actually, it's all okay. I go with it. Yeah, any attention is good.
Is it?
Uh-huh.
No, I don't think so. Not always.
Some attention is good.
Somebody has a theory. Jonathan
does.
Oh,
brother.
Jonathan, you're on After Opie and Anthony Live?
Hi. No, Jenny Hutt, the reason why she was mentioning Kate Upton was because she has an internet video that made her famous.
Kate Upton. Oh, right.
Oh, she did. Yes, that was the link from the original. Right, from what Sam was saying.
Oh,
correct. Thank
you
for that.
You're all about the internet sensations.
I love the internet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you must have been very excited. Did you know? You know what we found out today?
What?
There's these Asian people, a guy and a girl.
Yeah.
Who have made a parody video of my waiting for an
I
iPhone 5 for no reason.
Awesome. That video that you put up, Sam, made me joyful.
It did?
It just loved it. I don't understand how that woman is functioning, is on the earth, essentially.
I don't either.
Seriously,
but it's not my responsibility.
It isn't. But when you said to her, what's cool about this phone is it could take still pictures of moving images. And she said something, well, that's even better.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? The iPhone, Apple 5, like, it's bizarre.
E-Rock, you know Mikey Piff finally did something right?
Yes, he put it on the mashup homepage, on the Hits 1
that's right.
Facebook page.
I was listening to Hits 1
Go team.
Driving in. And they replay that weekend countdown all weekend. And this morning, since it's still technically the weekend, Mikey Piff came on and did his Web Watchers, where he talks about the viral video of the week or whatever.
That was you.
He was smart enough to put me up there, because he never would have. If I had listened to that and heard someone else, he never would have heard the end of it.
I think he was kissing your ass is what I think he was doing.
You really?
Yeah.
You don't think it was a matter of he deserves to be there? It was just Piff being like, this will get me on Sam's good side.
Yeah.
I think it did deserve to be there, so I don't even know what
I think
that...
it deserved to be there, too, but I don't think that's why he put it on there.
He's got ulterior motives.
Really?
That's what you're thinking, Eric?
I think so.
He's that type of guy, right?
It's in hope to get Roland to stop mentioning his name on this show.
Well, that's not going to happen, because, you know, Mikey Piff tried to take credit. He's a program director on Hits 1, and he tried to take credit for Carly Rae Jepsen being exposed on Sirius XM.
Oh.
It's just not the truth.
It was Bieber.
No, it was Sam Roberts and Troy Kwan on After Opie and Anthony Live.
I think I did know that.
Right, if you go to our Wikipedia page, you can see that Call Me Maybe first gained national radio exposure on this show.
Gotcha.
Which now you're on, so maybe...
Maybe that's going to help me.
Maybe your show will become a phenomenon. Where can people hear your show?
On Sirius XM Stars, 107 daily, 1 p.m. East.
1 p.m. on the East. Mm-hmm. So check out that, especially if you're ladies. You cater more towards the women.
I cater to both.
But on Fridays, you do sexy time with Jenny Hutt?
Yes. Well, not every Friday anymore, thank God, because too much conversation about the sex makes the sex less appealing.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Then this show has got it all wrong. Opie and Anthony need to take a lesson.
But yeah, no. Is that what they told you? Guys, too. No. I think here they'd be happy if I did sex shows every Friday.
You should do a sex show every single day.
Honestly, I want to go to work and then be in the mood to have sex when I get home. Yeah. And if I'm on the air talking about sex, it's like, then I'm done.
But that's what people want to hear about.
Right. They like hearing about sex, sure.
Of course. So you shouldn't be sitting there going, like, what makes me most comfortable? You should be
and I don't.
What is going to keep these listeners tuned? And if you're going on and being like, oh, my vagina did the craziest thing the other day.
Yeah.
I would listen to that show.
Oh, I always talk about vaginas. That comes up in conversation any day. Sure, my vagina is fair game on my show.
You should talk about it at least 3 times a week.
3 times a week, just mention my vagina?
Yeah, okay, and what's going on with it?
Right.
Kevin, you're on after Opie and Anthony
Live. It's clean.
Thank God.
Hey, Sam, I really enjoy the show.
Thanks.
I wanted to tell you a quick snippet from Glenn Beck's program, his radio program last Thursday. He actually made reference to the Apple V. I don't know if it was a subconscious thing or
you think
watched the video. I almost fell out of the truck last night. It was hilarious.
You think Glenn Beck is sitting at home watching my video?
What happened with that, but it was funny as hell.
Everyone was.
Corrected him. He didn't try to correct himself or anything. It was funny, man.
Or maybe Glenn Beck is just as dumb as that woman that was interviewing.
I wouldn't go that far now. I mean, he does a couple of silly things, mind you, but for the most part, he's pretty level. He's a little heavy on the religion side, but for the most part.
All right, thanks, Kevin.
Maybe Stump Brain sent it to him.
Yeah, Stump Brain probably did. Stump Brain, Mr. Moderate. Have you seen Stump Brain? He's called up a bunch of times. He was our old executive producer at CBS when we were at K-Rock. Have you seen his Twitter avatar that says the truth has no agenda?
No, it used to be a photo of his parents.
No, it says the truth has no agenda. But, like, isn't The Blaze an obvious right-wing website?
Yeah, but the truth has no agenda.
Like, can't right... What's wrong with right-wing people just be like, yeah, I'm right-wing? And left-wing people being like, yeah, like MSNBC should just be like, yeah, we're left-wing.
They need the drama and they the hypocrisy.
And if they admit to it, the drama's just not there.
Yeah, it's different.
Speaking of drama, is everything okay with you and Opie?
Yeah, I think so.
I heard you were mad at him.
I was really mad at him. I adore Opie. He's hilarious.
No, Opie told me. Opie told me he did not make you laugh.
Oh, no, he makes me laugh.
Eric, did you hear about what Opie did to Jenny Hutt?
The other day outside the building, I saw Opie, and we were talking, and I'm like, okay, let me take a picture, and I'll twit pick
it. He said...
And so these two guys were walking by that he knew, and I said, can one of you take the picture?
Here's what happened.
So then Opie goes, no,
listen,
and I'm like, oh, come
listen,
on,
Jenny
Hutt. And then
listen, Jenny
Opie
Hutt.
Had the guy here's what not take radio. The picture,
she doesn't
ran
know. Here's
away.
What happened.
I was there. You weren't.
Here's what happened.
What happened?
You guys were talking, you and Opie, having a nice chat.
Yeah.
You know, and it was all friends.
Yeah, of course.
And then. You were like, we don't have a picture together.
Let's
we should
pick.
Take a picture. Yeah. We should twit pick this.
Instagram.
And then Opie told me that even if he had said, oh, good idea, whatever, how did he respond when you said we should take a picture?
I don't remember.
Because he told me it wasn't something he wanted to do.
Obviously, because he didn't have
that's what he told
it.
Me in hindsight. So I don't know. He told me it wasn't
crazy.
Something he wanted to do. So what happens is it's not just two guys. Bill Burr and Joe DeRosa.
Right.
They're comedians.
Yes. And they that's why they were the funny guys and they brought the funny.
I mean,
in
Bill
the moment,
Burr is on Breaking Bad. You know Breaking Bad?
I don't watch it. It's too gritty for me.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
That goes with your too many Friday sex shows?
No, it's just that I can't deal with blood and gore. It freaks me out. The sex show thing is that I like sex. If you talk about it too much and you get too clinical, it becomes less sexy. Don't you agree? Don't you want to just fuck Sam?
Yeah, but then you want to come back and talk about it.
Yeah, but then
I would talk about it a lot more, but Jess gets
so
mad.
If you talk and you talk, how many blowjob conversations can I have?
Can I tell you something?
What?
You can have them every day for 4 hours a day.
And people will tune in?
That's the only reason people will tune in. Yes, that's why people will tune in. I mean, look at the... You're coming in...
Fellatio Friday.
How big is the Opie and Anthony show? It's a giant radio show.
Yeah.
What is the number one thing that's discussed?
It doesn't matter. It's just those two guys.
Fucking and blowjobs.
Right.
Right?
Well, that's men. That's men speak.
Well, you got to get the men.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine if it was like guys listening to you. Like,
I'm
listening to this Jenny Hutt. Not
I have
a bunch
some
of
guy
like.
Guy friends, fans. It's good.
You know, Sarah Palin hockey moms listening.
No, I don't think they're really who I cater to either.
Anyway, so what happened was.
You're telling my story.
Yeah,
It's important that I hear the real. This version.
Jenny posed next to Opie.
I did.
And said, can you guys take a picture of us?
I did.
And she handed the camera to Joe DeRosa.
And they put it on the ground and ran away.
And Joe said, yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. And he pointed the camera at Jenny and Opie.
And then he dropped it.
And then he put it down on the floor and
gingerly,
walked away.
Gingerly. He didn't damage
gingerly,
it.
Gingerly, right. But yeah. He put it down on the floor and walked
really
away.
I was really mad. I was like, funny mad.
And
like,
you go,
oh,
you guys are
so
assholes.
Mean. You're so mean.
And then
I don't think I said assholes. I said so mean.
You wouldn't want to use coarse language. While Jenny Hutt was picking up her phone, Opie then walked away.
Yeah, he did. It was sensational.
Without taking
a
picture.
It was a fine moment. I don't really blame him.
I don't believe
it. It was
funny as
shit.
I think this is positive. I can never be mad at anybody, Jennifer Hutt. How come you can't just be like, fuck, like, who's somebody
because
you don't
first
like?
First of all, because that wouldn't make me,
who's somebody
that wouldn't
you don't
make
like?
Me super angry. That's like baloney silliness.
Do you hate Martha Stewart's daughter?
No, not, I don't, no.
Why?
Well, I'm thankful. I had like 6 good years with her.
I'd be so fucking pissed at her if I was you.
No, it's so long ago. We haven't talked in a year. I don't even.
Who's somebody you don't
care?
Like? Do you like your kids, or is there one that...
I love my children.
Is there one that you're not terribly fond of?
No, I like them both the same.
I know. I see them on Instagram all the time. You love your kids.
I love
my
babies.
You love your family so much.
There's nothing we could do about that.
Yeah. Now, who don't you like?
I think I don't like people who are... I mean, if anyone's mean to my family, that doesn't work for me.
Right. But if they're mean to you, it's okay.
I could deal with it. Usually, I can see the reason why someone's obnoxious to me. It's usually not even about me. People don't care enough, really, about me to be mean.
What's it about?
Themselves, whatever's going to make them feel better or feel good that day. And
I
so that's
see.
Fine. I'm
so
just
you don't
sort of
mind
the
conduit. Them. You don't mind them.
What?
Taking out whatever their frustrations are on
you.
You
don't really
care.
Most,
it's a little bit of a doormat,
stuff,
though.
It's not because things can roll off of me, but my self-esteem is pretty good. Like I know I'm a good person.
Right.
So what? If
you're capable. You feel capable?
I am capable.
You feel talented? Do you think you're a talented
good
person?
At my job, Sam.
You think you're?
I can also sing a little bit.
Yeah. What do you sing?
I could just sing. Like, I don't, but I
what's
can.
What's one song you like to sing?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I can sing.
Like
but
what?
I don't, anything. I
like
don't
what's your favorite musical?
What's
you like Cats?
No, I don't like
that's
Cats.
That's a great musical.
That is not, I'm not a fan of Cats.
Do you like Little Shop of Horrors?
I love Little Shop of Horrors.
We had Frank Oz in here the other day.
Right, I didn't get to speak to him, but
you're
I
love
that song,
Opie
Somewhere
Anthony
That
level.
Screamed. I'm not, mm-mm.
Okay, how
not.
Does the song go, Somewhere That Screamed?
Oh, come on.
How does it go? E-Rock, would you like to hear Jenny
no,
Hutt sing Somewhere
That
Screamed?
Why
not?
She should sing along with it.
Yeah, put it on.
Do you want to karaoke? Keep it low, though,
no,
Eric.
Put on the music, and then we can... Do you sing, Sam?
I sing all the time. But I need to hear you sing it first.
But I can't
goes.
Hear it.
All right, Jenny Hutt.
I'm trying to find a non-Broadway
a
one.
A matchbox of our own, a fence of real chain link.
Yeah, you know the words. She knows the words.
I like The Little Mermaid. I like...
You like that racist crab, Sebastian?
Undead SC.
Yeah, that's some racist shit.
Why?
Well, come on. He's not supposed to be black?
I know. I didn't think about that.
Do you have it, Eric?
That's okay,
yeah,
I don't need it.
I just have a Broadway version.
Okay, let me just play a little bit of the Broadway version.
I like Defying Gravity.
Okay, sing along.
Sing along.
Sing along.
No.
You have the
no,
music now.
Hang on, I'm restarting.
No, go to Glee.
You
no,
don't know how
go
to do
put
radio.
On Defying Gravity.
What's Defying Gravity?
From Wicked. Are you kidding me? Something has
you.
Changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the whatever. You don't
why don't
know
you
it?
Do singing video? No, I don't know.
I do.
Wicked.
I did one with Lance Bass and I are singing on YouTube.
Always trying to find those. What do you think of this?
You
tell
didn't
me.
See that?
Do you
funny.
Dislike?
What
is E-Rock one of the people you dislike?
No, I like E-Rock.
He takes more shots at you when you're
you
in here
what?
Than anyone.
I don't care.
Every time you're
she
in here,
stop. Talking to hear what's being said in here.
What are you saying,
so?
Sweet Pea?
Well, Sam was trying to talk in several conversations we were having on this show, and you plowed right through when he's like, all right, hang on a second, and you didn't let him reset or explain what you were talking about.
Please reset and explain, Sam.
Well, that's already been done now. But E-Rock kind of, he takes shots the whole time you're in here. Like, if you're listening, listen, this is a reason to get SiriusXM on demand at SiriusXM.com, because you can download this show and just listen for E-Rock's little exasperated sounds
zingers
from the other room.
And heavy sighs.
I have Little Shop song, and I have that Wicked song.
I like the Wicked
okay,
song.
Okay, play the Wicked song low, and then Jenny Hutt will sing over
okay.
it.
Okay.
Elphaba, why couldn't you stay calm for once?
Instead of flying off the handle.
I hope you're happy.
Come on.
I hope we're happy now. This isn't the part I like.
Oh.
It happens a little later in the song. I like it.
Oh, God.
I hope you're happy. It's a duet.
Broadway stinks.
How you would grovel in submission to please your own ambition. You don't know this. You don't know this.
She's not going to sing along, Eric. I don't want to hear it anymore.
I hope you're
are happy right now.
It's not bad. Not bad. She can hold it down.
I can sing.
She can hold it
down. Just go to YouTube.com/JennyHutt. There's a video of me singing with Lance Bass. It's silly.
How come not?
It's cute.
Are you not shopping these videos? It seems like you should have had a video by now that's like, you know.
I'm not. I'm like, I'm haphazard about it. I'm not as deliberate as you are.
Yeah, I was shopping that shit out to everyone.
Yeah. No, I don't even know how to do that, though. How do you do that?
You just send it to people.
How?
Well, you get, there's like a electronic mail now that you could use. It's like regular mail, but it's on a computer, and you type in, everybody's got a specific address. You could send it to them that way.
Oh, there's can you do that on the Apple 5?
Yes, there's Twitter you could use, but you can't just tweet out your video link one time.
See, I feel like a douche if I multi-tweet. No?
Yeah, but who's
the point of doing a viral video, though?
Yeah, who's paying attention to every single tweet you tweet?
No one.
I follow you, and I don't see every tweet you tweet.
I know, I have to direct it to you in order for you to see it.
I look at my mentions. Yeah,
of course.
But, like, yeah, tweet out your video a few times. Find reasons.
Okay, so there's a video of me dancing with Elmo, Gangnam Style. That's a good one.
Right. Gangnam Style is, like, the big shit. The Morning Mashup tried to do a Gangnam Style video.
Yeah.
It's just them with Psy, though.
Yeah, that's good, too.
Yeah, but you got one with Elmo.
Yeah, and he was fun.
And how many times has Elmo done Gangnam Style?
Yeah, not a lot.
Does anybody ever come to you and be like, I don't want to do a video with you?
T.I. didn't want to do a Gangnam Style video. I asked him to. He was like, no, I don't do that.
He did?
Yeah, he said no.
I did a one question in one of my one question interviews with T.I.
Yeah.
Asking him what his favorite Skittle was. He refused to answer.
Why?
However, him saying, I don't have a favorite Skittle, Chief, sorry. Well, that was the answer. I said, that's fine. That's the answer.
That
to the
is
interview.
An answer.
How come he didn't want a Gangnam Style with you?
He just wasn't into it. I think he's a serious guy. I don't think he likes to.
What?
I think he's a little bit serious.
He's got a reality show.
I know, but on my show, he was a little bit serious. He wasn't super chill. Other people are chill. He was not. But I don't. Sometimes I think I shouldn't ask people to make videos, even though I want them to.
Yeah.
But. You don't mind asking anybody, right?
No, I don't. Well, no, I would never. I would never ask a celebrity to make a video.
Well, that's what I mean. So
I would never do it.
You just wouldn't ask?
No, because it's like, why would I want? I wouldn't want somebody being like I wouldn't want a listener to come up to me on the street and be like, if they come up to me and be like, hey Sam, love your show. I'm like, yeah, you're the man. I'm so happy to meet you. But if they come up to me and be like, hey Sam, I love your show. Will you do a video with me? I'd be like, no, I don't want to do a video with you.
Oh, no, I'd probably say yes.
Why?
Because I don't mind. It's fun.
But I'm trying to, you don't want to control your image a little bit?
What image?
That's right.
I'm just Jenny. Hence the name of my show.
That's branding, though.
And my website. No, it's not. It's actually true.
But that makes you very accessible, no?
I think I am very accessible. I think I'm like the most approachable person probably ever.
So if you want Jenny to be in a video for you.
There you go.
Just find her on the street and she'll do it.
Yeah, find me and
so
I'll
if some
say
stranger
yes.
just walked up to you and was like, oh, Jenny, you're Jenny Hutt.
Yeah,
I've heard you.
If I was having a tragic hair day or something, I might say no, but yeah.
I heard you on After Opie and Anthony Live.
Mm-hmm.
I know you're having a tragic hair day today. That's obvious. But would you do.
I'd probably still say yes. What'd you call me earlier? What'd you call me? A doormat? I don't think I'm a doormat.
A little bit of a
doormat. I think I'm just easygoing in that way in relating to people. Eric, I like to interact with human beings.
If one of our listeners came up to you and you didn't know who they were, it's not like a celebrity listener. We're not talking about a Coke Logic or a Larry or a Struff or someone like that. We're talking about some weirdo.
Yeah.
Let's say Marcos from Yonkers, for argument's sake.
Uh-oh.
If he comes up to you and goes, hey, Eric, I want to do a video with you. Will you do it? What
no,
would you?
That's weird.
Yeah, just no.
But you'll, no. But Jenny will do any video?
Not yeah. any video,
like
but
if
yeah.
some guy says, hey, I want to do a casting couch video?
No, that I will not do.
Like, what if somebody was like, oh, I want to do a viral video? And you're like, okay, cool, let's do it. And he's like, all right, take your pants off.
No, that won't happen. I've got kids.
Good for you, Jenny.
Yeah.
It's good to see that you have standards.
I have boundaries.
I was worried that you didn't have any. You're just
I
a
have
loose,
boundaries.
Flighty woman.
I
what
can't...
if it's one of those videos where they keep offering her more money to do stuff?
Yeah,
what
yeah.
type of stuff?
And you go in the bus?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, sure, that type of video.
Like, we'll give you $200 to do jumping jacks, and then the price goes up for each thing you're willing to do.
Well, that I would...
And then you're naked in a bus and
a
hotel.
No, I'm not getting naked in a bus or a hotel. That's not going to work out.
Roland is the weirdest kid guy ever.
I like Roland.
Well, I don't know what he means, if this is an insult or not.
Oh, no.
He texted me, and he said, she is a tampon of videos.
What?
Does that mean anything to anyone?
I don't know what that even means.
In that it absorbs, it's absorbent?
I don't, Maybe.
Is that a compliment?
Brand of tampon? I
maybe
don't...
your videos absorb attention the way a tampon
it blocks
absorbs
good videos from coming through.
Period blood?
It's.
Because tampons absorb,
no,
they don't block, they absorb.
No, I know what a tampon does, but I they,
that's a compliment. Your
I'm
videos
not,
absorb attention.
And, I'm not sure that's what he meant. I don't know what he meant.
And period.
Yeah, blood.
Period, blood, and urine.
Yeah, not urine.
There's some urine in there.
There is not urine in there.
I mean, there's got to be
it's
some.
It's a different hole, Sam. No.
Yeah, but it's around the same
no,
area.
No, sweet pea,
Eric,
it's not.
Eric, settle this argument. Period. It's a little blood and a little
no,
urine, right?
No, period is yeah. all blood.
It's a little
guys.
Urine, too,
it all comes
right?
through the same chamber.
Yeah, exactly.
No, guys, it doesn't come through the same chamber. That's the thing.
Steve in Philly wants to do a viral video with you, Jenny.
All right, Steve.
Yeah, Steve.
What would that be?
I have a great idea for one, actually.
Oh, no.
It starts with a car chase.
Oh, brother. And then I shoot myself, kind of like what was aired on Fox last week.
See, Steve would be
Thank
Chef
you,
Smith
Steve.
In this case.
Thank you for that.
Get it off, Sam. Get it off.
Would you do that video, or is that a little... That's
I mean, that video, that is such a horrible story.
Which, well, I mean...
The whole thing is bad.
And why did the guy kill himself? Did you ever find out?
How would I know?
I don't know. You said you did a horrible story. It sounds like you know
I
the
just,
story.
He was chased and he killed himself. He clearly was not a happy guy.
Must have been scared.
Yeah.
He's on bath salts.
What?
Maybe he
like,
was on bath salts.
On bath salts.
He could have been. Did you hear about the woman who bit Danny Bonaducci's cheek?
No, that's awesome. What do you mean?
She went up to him and yeah. she was like, oh, can I give you a kiss? And Danny Bonaducci was like, of course you can. I'm Danny Bonaducci.
Yeah.
I'm fucking crazy. And then he leaned in and he offered his cheek to her. And she just sunk her teeth in.
So now she need, he needs
And like people had to, like she wouldn't release.
That's
people had
sick.
To come. She bit part of his cheek off.
That's really unsettling.
Maybe bath salts. I don't know. Have you ever done bath salts?
No, I'm not a drug person though.
Have you ever done any drugs?
Yeah, I've tried marijuana.
You did. How was mm-hmm. that for you?
Grass. I never really liked it. I never got into it.
No?
I tried when I was a sophomore in college. I tried to smoke pot a few times.
But what if smoking weed is the creative yeah. outlet that you need to
not
make?
For me.
The viral video of a lifetime.
Yeah, not going to work.
No?
And I don't like alcohol, so... And I once tried mushrooms.
Mm-mm. How was the mushrooms?
I thought that was freaky, but it exhausted my mind so much the next day. I never did it again.
I think if you did mushrooms...
Yeah.
You'd like to think that you'd just see, like, unicorns and rainbows and stuff like that. But I think if you did mushrooms, you'd see all the terrible, horrible things that you just push down.
I don't want to do that.
Because I don't think they bounce off you. I think
I
you push
that.
It all down.
I don't want that.
I think
you
it's
do?
In you.
No, it's
I
not.
Do.
I'm actually, I'm so like, no, I'm really, I've been through enough therapy in my life that.
Are you still in therapy?
No.
You should, mm-hmm. Don't you think?
I go in and out. Like if I
oh,
need it,
okay.
I'll go get a tune-up.
Is that what it is now? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like the car's been built. We're
yeah.
done. We're ready to go. But
yeah,
every now and then we get inspection.
Yeah. I just know it's not about me. I think if you could take away, if you could realize the criticism really isn't in fact about you,
right.
then it hurts less.
Oh, that's what you learned in therapy.
No, I think that's just what I've learned in life.
Oh, you didn't learn
People
that in therapy?
People are caught up in their own trip, Sam.
Yeah. Not so. Me. I'm all about everybody else.
I know.
I'm not into myself at all.
You're very selfless.
Yeah, I'm a selfless person.
I love that about you.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Now, but is it going to drive you back into therapy when Eric started deep sighing and Roland said you were a tampon video or whatever it
no,
was?
No, not at all. Cause
no?
No, I like these guys. It's all okay.
Even with the deep sigh. Eric, do
yeah,
the deep sigh so she can hear it. That's what he was
that
doing
hurts.
While
that
you were talking. You know,
that
and
hurts
it's like,
a little bit.
Come
all
on.
Right.
She's
okay.
a guest on the show.
I'm fine.
Do you think Jenny would do a video where she's just shopping at a clothing store and it ends with her and a guy in a dressing room?
Yes.
Would you do that?
Yes, but I wouldn't yeah. actually have sex with the guy.
Oh, why not?
I'd imply it.
Why would you should do a video for RedTube?
What's that?
It's the porno website. That would get views. That's what we were talking about with the sex.
I have children and a husband.
You could make more on the video.
Just take my husband and bring him right to the gutter.
Well,
with
if
me.
Your if your husband wants to do it,
mm-hmm.
he could be in it. And, but you'd be
face.
Like, you'd be like, listen, you knew mm-hmm. I was getting into entertainment before.
Yeah.
You know this is
oh,
part
he's
of the
so
job.
Supportive.
Right.
He's amazing.
So it's time for you to be supportive and realize I need to make a fuck movie. And you can be in it if you want.
This would not be good for
but
my
But you
this
say
would not
this.
Be a positive
I understand if it embarrasses
children.
You.
No, it just wouldn't be right to my children.
They could be in the room watching just so they know mommy is okay with this. Or not. That's up to you.
Perfect.
Although, uh-huh. legally, they could not be.
No, and I just, as a parent, I would not feel okay about it.
But I'm
that.
A don't ask, don't tell type of person. If I hear a little kid voice in
yeah.
the background of the video,
yeah.
I want to ask you if it's
Let
yours.
Let me ask you, are you going to have kids anytime soon? Or are you thinking about that?
Anytime soon or anytime?
Yeah.
I mean, within the next few years, I would think so, probably.
It's fun.
You know, I'm 6 years away from 35. So sometime in that time frame,
you're such a baby.
It's wonderful to be young.
Oh my God!
I'm sure you kind of remember, but it's,
no, I don't. It's actually, it's a distant memory. All. It is so distant.
It's
my
like
God.
When Damian Eccles was in here, he said he was in jail for so long that he forgot what it was like on the outside.
I forget what it's like to be in my 20s.
You've been not young for so long.
42. It is painful.
You forget what it was like to taste pizza as a kid.
I just forget what it's like to taste pizza without feeling guilty.
Right. You feel a lot of guilt with what you're eating. How's your... I mean, you're doing a good job, though, of keeping weight off.
Thanks.
You used to be fat. You're not fat anymore.
Well, I work hard to not be fat.
You wear Spandex pants every day.
I wear Spandex a lot.
That's what Opie was telling me. He said you were in some stupid... He said... This
always.
Is an Opie quote. He said she had in some stupid fucking pants. And
I
she
do,
was
always.
Asking me to take a picture.
I wear a lot of stupid pants.
Why is
them.
That? You just like
they're
them.
Very comfortable. They feel like sweats, but they're not, and they're tight. They keep me honest.
And it shows off your body.
It keeps me honest.
Which you're proud of.
No, it keeps me honest.
Is
like,
that...
I know I can't wear stretchy pants if I let my ass get the size of Topeka, Kansas.
And is that a mechanism to maintain this weight
it
loss?
It helps, sure.
Because you're
and
like...
jeans help. I put on jeans a lot to make sure my jeans fit. And I weigh myself every day. I'm a wacko.
And what does your husband think of all this?
Because, like... It's funny.
When Jess was on, like, his, her crazy wedding diet, because she didn't need to lose any weight.
Yeah.
And, not to say... I mean, I know before you did need to lose weight.
I did. I was fat.
But now you don't need to lose any weight.
Right. So I just don't want to gain weight. So to not gain weight, I have to work very hard.
But he doesn't get tired of you being obsessed with
no,
the dieting.
Backs. I think it's funny.
He just pushes it all down, too. There's a lot of resentment in the Hutt household.
We're together 17 years. We're
yeah.
Good.
It just, you just push it away.
I think my Energy Kitchen might be here. Hello, is this Energy Kitchen?
Is it?
You're downstairs. Okay, I'll be down
like
in a minute.
When Roland
Thanks.
Orders food
Thank
during
you.
The
Bye.
Staff meeting.
Well, you know, I didn't know. This was not like during a staff meeting.
Roland once left our staff meeting early because tacos were downstairs.
That's so funny.
And he said...
He was hungry.
He said, I'll be right back. I have to go get tacos from downstairs.
Yeah.
He never came back.
I never resurfaced.
He went back to the office and ate his tacos.
Oh, my gosh.
I guess he didn't realize that, you know, just because you got them right then doesn't mean you have to eat them immediately.
Right.
Real quick, before you go.
Oh, boy.
To get your... I wanted... See, I was holding off on these calls, but if you're talking about leaving for Energy Kitchen...
Yeah.
Bob, in Illinois, you're on After Opie
Anthony
Live.
Holy shit. How much did she pay you to get her on the radio, Sam? Go get your Energy Kitchen shit. Just shut up for 1 minute.
You don't like Jenny Hutt? I like Jenny Hutt.
That's okay.
She is kind of funny sometimes, but today I thought, oh, man.
Oh, well, maybe that's not doing my job then.
Not you, Sam.
You don't think it's me?
I think you're perfect.
Oh, thank you so much. Luke in Massachusetts.
Oh, it's Sammy. What's up, buddy?
How's it going, dude?
I'm not
going
to spend 30 seconds introing you.
Luke is another regular, by the way. I've got lots of regulars.
I'm sure you do.
Very popular.
You are popular.
That's right. 4.5
Luke
million
using
views.
Force. Luke using force on Twitter.
That's right.
I'm thinking that you pulled something on us, because Jenny Hutt sounds just like that girl from the video. Did you overdub that?
That's okay. Hilarious.
Okay. Let's put this on the record right now, Jenny Hutt.
Yes.
You had nothing to do with the production of waiting for an iPhone 5
nothing.
For no reason.
Nothing at all.
You enjoyed it at home just like everybody else.
Loved it.
Jenny Hutt is not the plant put into the iPhone 5 video.
I am not.
You know, somebody actually came up to me, like people who work here, who I've never met before.
Yeah.
Like up on the 37th floor, which is all like legal people in suits and offices
office
and stuff.
My office is up there. Oh, I'm a lawyer.
It's not fun up there. Somebody actually came up to me and said, hey, Sam. And I said, yeah? I thought I was in trouble. I thought it was HR. And they were like, seriously, is the girl in your video real? I was like, yeah, it's real. Oh, it's really funny.
I asked you that, though. I texted you. I said, hey, man, that girl real? And you were like, yep. I said, oh, wow.
Nobody believes she's real.
I believe you. I was just curious.
Yeah. All the comments have been fake, fake, fake.
No, she's, wow.
I mean, she's a talented performer.
She is something special.
Yeah, I think so,
too. Mm-hmm.
Well, why don't you plug? We will plug also Todd Rosken. His movie about Russ Meyer is at 1:30 p.m. Eastern time today at the Lincoln Center Theater, whatever it is. If you're in New York, head over to the Lincoln Center at 1:30.
Okay.
Jenny Hutt, where can people hear you on the radio?
Okay, I'm on SiriusXM Stars 107. You can follow me on Twitter at Jennifer Hutt.
Mm-hmm.
And my website's just jenny.com.
And you can see all her viral video goodness.
That's right.
And she makes these treadmill videos.
I
and
do.
She tries to show a little cleavage. And we are going to reinstate Fuck Fridays, and that's what we're going to call it.
Fucking nice. Fridays. Well, it used to be Dirty Frisky naughty F me Friday.
It's too much. Just call it.
Okay, fuck Fridays.
Fuck Friday. Can you say fuck on your show?
Yeah, of course. I can say whatever I want.
Okay. Will you listen to Fuck Fridays, Eric?
Sure. Will Jen do a video where she's hitting on her daughter's boyfriend, like at the dinner table?
See, that would be a video.
I mean, my daughter's 12.
So that's even better. Be like, oh.
Oh, Jesus, guys. Come
what's
on.
Up?
What about dropping a towel when pizza's delivered?
Yeah, and you could be like, oh, I didn't know they made pants that tight for a 12-year-old. And he'd be like, what do you say, Miss Hutt? And you'd be like, they just got a little tighter, didn't they?
Oh, God, that
and
is
and just kind of say stuff like that. Like,
you guys are really disgusting.
Send your daughter off to the kitchen.
I got
to
go. Sam, thanks for having me on. Even with all the hate calls
she's
I just got.
Been in the kitchen
I'm
for
cool.
40 minutes.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Keep her in there. The door
thanks,
locks.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, Jenny Hutt, for stopping by. Jocktober continues tomorrow. Ron and Fez are up next, and we'll be back with more of this tomorrow as well. Goodbye.
The Opie and Anthony Show is now over. For real this time. Check out the O&A Show on Facebook at facebook.com/Opie and Anthony. And catch Opie and Anthony live Monday through Friday from 6 to 10 a.m. Eastern. Ron and Fez are next.
Hey.